But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Look at that. Easy as that.
Easy as that.
And it's Friday.
Oh my God, what happened?
We were just bitching that it was Monday, and then the earth spins around a few times, and here we are, it's Friday!
I'm in on that one.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to do that one with you.
Audio's on, suck it.
Well, we didn't get a Sully this time around, huh? It figures, too. Life has a way of doing that to everybody. You feel good about something. Everyone's riding the high. And then whatever you believe in, whether it's a god in the sky or if you believe in nothingness after you die.
Yeah.
This life thing has a way of kicking you in the teeth and keeping it real.
Keeping it real. The fun stories, the happy stories, they don't last forever, do they?
No. I went to bed early, so I didn't know about this. I come walking in, and everyone's like, hopefully no one was on that plane, because, you know, I spent a lot of time up in Western New York. 3 years in Buffalo.
Yeah.
Plane goes down, what, in Clarence? Clarence Center? Hit a house.
What's your clearance, Clarence?
Hit a house, 49 dead.
Oops.
There's going to be no Sully this time around.
No.
And I was telling Anthony in the office, you think the pilot, you know, as soon as he knew there was something wrong with the plane, was like, I'm going to be the next Sully. And he's probably dreaming of his interview with Larry King and
like,
the Today Show and Good Morning America.
Trying to bring it in going, I'm going to be the guy.
Oh, my God, I'm the new Sully. All right.
Let me think.
All right, here we go. All right, here we go. What do I do first?
Ladies and gentlemen, brace for impact. What will I do? Let's see. Should I do Leno or Letterman?
Right.
First, Larry King's an idiot. Won't do him.
Yeah.
Oh, boy, we sure are going in fast, though. There's no water. Damn it.
Maybe I could bounce off a couple of these roofs and land in a tree.
Terrible tragedy.
Honestly.
First commercial airline deadly crash in the U.S. in 2 years. So
he wanted to do the new Sully, but then on the way down he realized he was, but they're going from Godsmack.
And he
can't fly either.
No.
No. But, that's weird. That's the first one with casualties.
There's
been a bunch of incidents in the last year, hasn't there? Couple running off the runways.
Yes.
And landing in the river and what not.
Well, this is technically not even Continental. I mean, it is, but they use Continental's but they don't
logo,
have, I don't believe they have the same maintenance crews as Continental. That's why I hate these smaller flights. Like, did they have the Embraer jets, the 51-seaters? I don't know what kind of plane this
one had. 74, let's call it. Yeah, for real.
Yeah,
49 died, 48 in the plane, one on the ground, and, you know, it wasn't a full flight, obviously. They had an extra 20 or so seats.
Oh, okay.
But it's so weird you're saying that, Jimmy, because literally Monday, Kenny was saying that you refused to fly those type of planes, and I slightly rolled my eyes, like, come on, what could, you know, I used to fly these planes all the time when I was living in Western New York, because a lot of times you don't have a choice.
Right.
You know, they give you one of these prop
planes. What are you going
to
do?
You don't know, well... Especially me, I didn't know, you know, next thing you know, you're walking up to the prop plane and getting on.
Yeah.
It's a quick ride to Buffalo. I've probably done that exact flight 10 times over the years.
This was a prop?
Yeah.
They introduced those.
That's what I'm saying. So with you telling Kenny just recently that you wouldn't fly those, I'm like, come on. I've flown them all the time. Never had one issue. And here it is. Literally 3 or 4 days later, this thing goes down.
Yeah, it's like... They seem to add them. Like, I don't remember Continental having them. I remember them having the Embraers, the 51-seaters were jets, so I would fly them. And then the Pittsburgh route, I noticed, started having these prop planes. And I'm like, well, you got to get us one that's a jet. I'm not flying the prop.
Mm-hmm.
But again, it could have been a jet.
I've been on even the smaller ones where I think it's only 3 seats across, which is weird. There's one seat on one side and then 2 on the other. I'm like, how does that work?
Yeah, weight-wise, right?
You would think it'd go 2 and 2 or 1 and 1, but 1 and 2.
That type I've never been on. That's one of those really kind of long ones.
Yeah.
I've been on a shorter version of those, the Umbrella, like Jimmy said. But, it looks, in my professional, unprofessional opinion...
Yeah, but you know a lot about flight.
Looks like icing.
You're going with icing?
Yeah, it was kind of cold, windy, and just when a plane loses lift like that, comes right in.
They said
in that kind of weather around Buffalo.
They said it just dropped out of the sky, man.
And they said a couple of other pilots in the area had reported ice building up on their wings.
Right.
So you get a situation like that. Especially, I heard a gentleman speaking saying that that plane was delayed at Newark for a while. And you get the flight crew, they're human, they get a little tired. Start using that autopilot for the flight. And then if ice builds up, the autopilot will try to compensate for it.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll keep compensating until it kicks off. And when it kicks off, it throws it back into the pilot's hands, very unstable. The autopilot can actually handle it to a point, but it starts putting the airplane in a very precarious pitch where it's trying to keep the plane flying by giving it more power and putting the nose up higher and higher to try to give it lift. But in the meantime, it's slowing down. It's losing lift because of the ice on the wings and the angle of attack, they call it, how high up the nose is.
Right.
And, if it kicks back to the pilot at that point, the pilot's like, what the, what am I, I'm trying to control this thing now. And you get a wing over or the nose will just dip and...
it's over, Johnny.
Kablooey, as I like using technical jargon.
Colgan Air, by the way. That's who operated this flight, Colgan Air.
With the Colgan.
Exactly.
With the Continental logo, though, on the side.
Yeah, they
our partners.
Yeah, our partner airlines, yes.
Yes, we're in partnership with many airlines, like Colgan.
Because we're not dumb. We're not going to fly. What is this?
Colgan Air.
Who's flying Colgan Air?
Nobody.
Everybody, when there's a big Continental on the side.
You ever fly an airline? I think you and I did it, Ant, when we had a flight out of Atlanta.
Ooh.
Where the check-in area is pretty much an area that they just gave this airline.
Wasn't that the time they just painted those air...
I forgot the name.
Those value jet planes with the AirTran logo?
Oh, yeah. And I was on the payphone at the time because I don't think we had cell phones.
Well,
with Bob going, Bob, I'm not flying on this thing. One of these went down. They just painted over the logos.
Like, we don't want to do this.
And he's like, it's their hub down. That's all they fly. That's it. You gotta
go down.
You gotta get on the plane. Thanks for talking me into possibly dying, Bob. I appreciate it.
We must go on.
Mm-hmm. So, 49 dead.
Wow.
God, what's going on with flying?
Well, it's still, the safest form of transportation.
We're all feeling good about that, but everyone is thinking about it now.
Yeah.
Everybody.
Yeah.
I mean, we're heading toward a vacation. I'm starting to think, all right, where can I drive to? And don't call up with, hello. You have a better chance of dying if you drive to the airport. You know that. Yeah, but it doesn't make you feel good when you're in the air. It's all about what makes you feel good.
At least in a car, it's like, oh my God! And you're gone. In a plane, it's just like, all right, what's our altitude? How much longer do I have before I perish?
Yeah.
I really get a chance to think about this.
You know, some of these plane crashes, you scream to the point where you lose your voice and you get tired of screaming.
Yes.
And then everyone's just sitting there looking at each other like, all right.
Like Homer.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Exactly.
Chick pilot?
Are we talking saying? Chick pilot?
Uh-oh. McFly.
Hey, McFly, how are you?
Pretty good. Hey, but boys, happy birthday, Jimmy, all that good stuff. Yeah, Chick was a pilot.
Now, I'm not saying that means anything. I'm sure a woman can fly just as good as a man, but you know what I like? I like combat pilots flying your plane.
You like Sully.
I like guys that have flown in fighter jets. Sully, he was a F-4 Phantom guy. Not many women come from a background of flying actual fighter aircraft because, not really allowed in combat.
We're just allowing
them. They have them.
Right.
They have women pilots. Not a lot of them.
Right.
But they don't fly in combat, really, and, usually support missions, things like that. But I kind of like a guy that could land a plane after it's been shot at. Mm-hmm. That to me is the ultimate.
Or land in a river after the geese take out two eggs. You think Sully's going to be all over the news as the expert?
Oh, Sully's going to be all over the expert.
They're clamoring to get Sully. Yeah.
Oh, if we can only get Sully. Sully, how is this exactly like your accident?
Right, right.
Only different with debts and icing and no water, houses.
Unbelievable. We got some air traffic control audio.
Ooh.
Hogan 3407, turn left heading 310.
Left heading 310, Hogan 3407,
approach. Hogan 3407, Buffalo. Delta 1998, look off your right side about 5 miles for a dash 8. Should be 2300. Do you see anything there?
Negative Delta 1998.
We're just in the bottoms and nothing on the
T-cast. Hogan 3407, Buffalo. COVID-3407, Buffalo Tower, how do you hear? Ground communication. You need to talk to somebody at least 5 miles northeast. Okay, possibly Clarence. That area right in there, Akron area. Either state police or sheriff's department need to find out if anything is on the ground. This aircraft was 5 miles out, and all of a sudden we have no response to that aircraft.
Five.
All I can tell you is the aircraft over the marker, and we're not talking to them.
Holy, that, like, just like that.
Yeah, that was it.
That thing must have went down fast. It probably wasn't that high in the air anymore if it was only 5 miles out. Huh?
1,500? Oh, that's you cannot recover from anything at 1,500.
And they're showing Newark Airport with the same planes all grounded, it looks like.
Well, they probably wouldn't be leaving at this hour anyway. As long as, maybe some of them would be. I don't trust those planes. I mean, maybe they're well maintained.
Meow, meow,
yep.
Meow, meow, no. I want.
Yeah, there's one of the wings just sticking out of the ground.
Oh, the tail is just popping out of the
house. God. All right, and then we got this, a witness.
I knew something was up, and I thought to myself, what if that plane crashes? And right when I thought that, I heard a huge explosion over there. And in my periphery, I saw, like, out the window, I saw the orange flash, and I knew a plane crashed.
Yeah, well, that way to go. You just knew, huh?
He knew.
All right, good for you, because I don't think I would have known that there was a plane crash.
Shirley Heyman lives at the corner of Long and Maple. She was doing a puzzle. She heard the noise, and then she came to her window and couldn't believe what she saw.
I heard this awful noise. I went over to the kitchen window, and I seen this noise and this light coming down, and all of a sudden it went bang and fire, and I yelled to my husband. I says, get out of bed. I says, the plane must have landed.
Heyman originally thought the plane crashed in her yard, and the magnitude of this crash didn't hit her until much later.
And I thought maybe it was a little small plane. And then they tell me it's a big one. Now I don't think I want my daughter to come back from Florida.
Ever.
Ever. Just leave her there.
She probably doesn't want to see you anyway.
Wow. There you go. Just some of the audio we got so far.
That's pretty, God, that's creeping.
Well, we get kicked in the teeth today.
Man, you know, had a good streak going there.
Had
a couple of planes that had emergency landings, and everybody walked out hunky-dory.
Making it exciting for everybody.
And then you get
heroes, and, you know.
Yeah, just you get this.
Overall good feeling, and now... Everyone dead, just like it's supposed to be, usually, right?
God, that's terrible. Well, Godspeed, everybody.
That's the big story today. We got other things to do, and we'll certainly keep going back to this one as we get audio. Remember the big story from yesterday, the guy being dragged?
Yes.
They ID'd him. So we got an update on that story after the break.
And you'll be amazed at how they ID this man because he didn't have a wallet or any identification on him whatsoever.
I'm going to go with fingertips.
You want to change the subject and do tips on fingers? Fingertips. Yeah. Use moisturizer. Clip your nails.
Boo, 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 boo.
Oh my God.
Boo, boo.
I just looked at you like, I think he just had a mini stroke.
That was the second one of those in what, 12 hours? First last night in Buffalo?
Yeah. Yeah.
Phil in Brooklyn is saying those planes are engine driven, not propellers.
Oh, are they?
They had some.
Oh, they're turboprop, you dummy. They got jets, but they run a friggin' propeller. They're propeller planes.
All right. Opie and Anthony. Hey, a big good morning to everybody. Opie and Anthony. I want to promote my Twitter today for one reason, Anthony.
Twitter.
I think I finally took a picture of something that people would care about.
Ooh.
I mean, this Twitter thing, you take a picture of your breakfast and you pop it up there and some people will check that out.
What, your radiator cap? What did you,
Opie Radio on Twitter, but I spent the day in Huntington. I got my new car.
Yep.
I guess I should say thank you to the gang at Huntington Jeep. I shouldn't say guess. They were great, Keith and the guys.
Yeah.
And I paid for it. I didn't get no special deal.
Yeah, so back off.
Back off, man. This isn't Plugola, man. This is just me doing the right thing. They were very nice.
Yeah.
Helped me out. Made me very happy. And I drove away with a brand new vehicle yesterday. And I was telling Anthony, I stepped into this thing. I haven't been in a new car in 7 years. My last new car. My last new car was right around 9/11. Right before 9/11. A couple months before 9/11.
Ought one,
right. And I stepped into this thing. I sat in it. I went, wow, this is a flying car.
Oh, nice.
I'm not even joking. I'm like, wow, they've come a long way with this technology.
Great.
Because I refuse to drive with anyone. That's one of my things. If I could drive, I drive. Even if I have a crappy car.
That's what I do.
I've been in Anthony's really nice car a couple times in the passenger seat, sure. But I got the camera now. What? You back it up and there's a camera? What?
You got the old backup camera. Isn't that nice?
How much does that roll?
Dude, it helps so much. It's just like, and I never thought of it. I used to swing into places with the, with the just using the mirrors.
Yeah.
I still use the mirrors a lot, but you don't realize in those real tight spots how handy that camera is.
Yeah.
You can just back up and you don't, what you used to use was ka-chunk.
Oh, yeah.
All right, I hit the guy. Now I know I can't go any further.
A little tap-tap.
You go forward, ka-chunk.
Here in New York, they play bumper cars. Getting into spots. And you'll be sitting in a restaurant with a window seat, and you'll watch some dummy just messing up two nice cars to try to get to a spot. Back and forth. Ka-chunk, 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 ka-chunk.
You know it was the absolute worst, though?
Yeah.
In the era back in, like, the 80s when everyone had a god-effing car alarm. So you'd bump into one of the cars just while you're parking. It's like, I'm just trying to park my car.
Yeah, I saw what you did, Jimmy. How do you know that?
How do you do the sound perfectly?
We all know the but you know the pattern. You know the pattern of the whole.
Because
we all thought we had very important cars. How obnoxious were we? We had a piece of crap.
Oh, pieces of crap that would have the alarms.
That most people didn't give a crap about.
It was usually some dumb greaseball his Camaro and his baseball bat in his room. That alarm goes off, I'm going out there and I'm smashing head because I know the people that'll be breaking into it. All right.
We all had a dumb car alarm because we thought we had...
Yeah, so valuable.
Quite the whip. I gotta protect my whip.
Protect your whip.
Shut up. All nobodies with stupid cars. But anyway, I stepped into this thing and it was like futuristic, like touch screen and the GPS. What is that?
I
never used GPS.
Now you got GPS and stuff. Now all you need to do quickly while you're still all psyched on this is get your ass an easy pass.
I got that years ago.
No!
Yeah, man.
Wow, okay. I thought you were still.
I joined the easy pass generation and. God, a few years back.
I swear I thought you were still just...
Nope.
Voss doesn't have easy pass. Yeah, even Kenny loves it now.
It's the way to go. It's ridiculous to stop and try to find money for tolls and bridges and tunnels. Touchscreen. I got a hard drive.
Oh, hard drive.
All these distractions to make it easier to crash as I'm driving.
Right. That's what it is, too. It is a lot of distractions.
It's ridiculous, so... And I punched the door like I told you I would to break it in.
Did you? No, you didn't.
Yeah, you got it. Yes.
No.
Yes, and then you don't have to like be paranoid every time you jump in your new car.
You just deal with the OCD about it, because that's
I worry OCD. About it too. I don't feel like having to worry about a scratch here and a ding here. So what I do is I punch the door real hard and give it a little, where if you move around a little bit, you see where the indentation is. Just a little.
Yeah.
I guess he's starting a relationship.
Now I'm good.
Now I'm good.
And then I come back to the city last night. And I talking to the garage guys, you know, Jimmy and I live in buildings, and you got to park in the buildings. And they pile way too many cars into these garages, by the way, because they want to make as much money as
possible. Oh, yeah.
The guy actually looked at me and goes, wow, now that you got a new car, you get to be parked in the nice area of the garage.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's kind of
He openly
nice.
Said, he goes, I go, wait a minute, because my other car was a piece of crap. You just, like... parked it in weird spots in this facility. He goes, oh yeah, absolutely, that's how we do it. But he goes, now that you got the nice one, we're gonna park you all the way in the back with all the other new cars.
That's nice,
because they don't want to hear from us if all of a sudden they pull up the car and there's some kind of scratch or something on it.
Yeah,
you know. And he goes, I would advise that you take a nice little loop around the car for the next year. Nice little loop, make sure everything's okay.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
I have this I feel comfortable in the garage in my building because I feel like they take care of them. My old building, man, it was like you drop it off and you didn't want to see the guy getting in it. You wanted to just pretend that magic, put it safely somewhere,
yes.
And then brought it back.
Oh,
you're
my God.
So right,
yes.
Man. And I gave the guy a shiny, brand new fiver, said, take care of this. This is my baby.
You tell Ty Webb I'm gunning for him.
I actually gave him a lot more. I said, look, you know, obviously he's not going to pass around. I'm like, but look, let's try to take care of this for a little while. I haven't had a new car in 7 years.
When should you tip, Star, by the way? When I don't know when to tip the garage guys now, because I tipped them at Christmas, and now it's like...
I tip them a buck.
I tip them a buck.
No, because I'm only driving, like, on weekends. I when they pull up my car, $2. When I drop it back off, $2.
Oh, you do every time? I don't do it every
time. Yeah, but you're driving every day.
Yeah.
You're literally driving your car every day in New York, not me. My brand new car will sit there for 3 weeks now. Hence the reason why it took so long to get the new car in the first place.
Yeah.
But back to Twitter. So I spent the day in Huntington. I was taking pictures and just fooling around, but I took two pictures that might be of interest to the fans. FH Raleigh's, yeah, that might interest some of the fans. But I took a picture of Anthony's old house.
My old house. The one in Huntington that when me and Opa carpooling into work together, I would be dropped off there.
Yep.
Or I would drop Opa off and then drive there. And that's where me and the ex-wife lived. And a lot of people are commenting that it does look like the Amityville Horror House, which... it also did on the inside.
Yeah.
Which
they're saying, wow, it's a mini version of the Amityville Horror House.
Yeah.
I was going to editorialize the picture, and I was like, I'll leave it to Anthony. But then everyone, because they've been listening to the show for a long time, they're like, oh, were those the windows where the candles were lit? For romance night?
Yep. That door, the front door was open, the curtains are open downstairs, and the candles are all lit, and all I wanted to do was play Half-Life. And, I had a...
How does it make you feel to see that? You know that...
It's a little nostalgic. House.
That's it.
It's okay.
That's the house Aunt lived in Huntington.
That's also the house I was in when I broke up with her.
Yeah,
so
right. So this
has its happy moments.
It runs the gamut.
Yes. But that was my little house.
You know what's funny? That house could fit in your living room now.
Yeah.
Almost.
The time
almost.
And depending on how some companies do, I might be right back in that house again.
Well, what are you going to do? Next trip to Huntington, I'll take a picture of the house I lived in. But, you know, I spread out my Twitter stuff.
The tree house.
the tree house, right.
You had a wacky house in Huntington.
And I only had half the house. You had a whole house.
Whole house.
You had a whole house.
Well, if you remember, there were tenants that lived in the basement apartment.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
They went around the left side of the house as you look at it.
You're right.
And there were people that lived down there.
Yeah. And then I was going through some more boxes, getting all my stuff out of my mom's house, and I found two pictures. You guys showed Jimmy this.
Oh, yeah.
Two pictures of... the first time Ann and I worked together, I believe, or pretty much the first week we started doing radio together.
Yeah.
And I put those up on my Twitter account.
Oh, wow.
Opie Radio on Twitter, but And I point out to Anthony, look at me, always being the guy trying to promote and market the show. We're in the middle of a bit with a goat.
Oh, look at you.
And I'm trying to make it look natural that I'm holding a WBAB sticker in the shot.
He's got a sticker in the shot just to like...
Because I knew that, you know, the trade magazines, not even the real papers, like the radio trade magazines, oh, they would eat up this photo and print it. Because there's a goat in a radio station. That's crazy. And Anthony's trying to feed the goat. And I'm there, like, kind of like with my mouth wide open, and I'm holding a BAB sticker, reacting to what Anthony's doing. It's a perfect shot for the trades. A perfect shot.
Is that the picture of Brother Joe?
No, the other one. Yeah, the black and white photo, which was done in the mid-90s, by the way. I don't know why this is a black and white photo. I must have had a disposable camera or something. But that was the first day these guys came in and did what was my radio show back then.
That was the first day you guys met?
Yeah. I think so.
Show. I showed one Afro Wars, didn't I?
Yeah. Anthony with a massive Afro.
Danny, yes?
I just didn't realize how long Travis had been working with you guys.
It kind of looks like Travis. It looks like Carlin in the 70s during certain, when he had that those goofy half smiles, Brother Joe.
Yeah, true. Oh, God damn, that was a long time ago.
So I put those two pictures up on the Twitter account. But people are saying I got to bring them in and scan them because I didn't get a great shot of it. I mean, you get the idea, obviously, right?
Yeah.
So
I think it's very funny to look at.
I was digging through boxes, and I'm like, you got to be kidding.
You holding that sticker is so
typical,
so like radio.
always thinking about the marketing angle.
Oh, of course.
Always.
Why not?
What are you going to do? So join me on Twitter, Opie Radio. We have a good time. I showed the inside of my car yesterday on the way out to Huntington with my satellite radio just like hanging sideways, like swinging.
Precariously?
That was the inside of my car.
Wait, why don't you have it installed? They don't do it?
I installed it in the air vent for a while. And then it just kind of, you know, that's the original unit.
Oh, this is not your new truck.
No.
Oh, okay.
Oh, imagine
that's what I thought. Like, Jesus, dude.
Here's your satellite radio, idiot.
That's what I thought you meant.
No, can you imagine?
But they did a very sloppy job. That's shoddy workmanship.
No, I wrote inside old car.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just so people aren't confused. And then people like commenting on a couple of the CDs I had laying in there. Mute Math and Management. And getting all sorts of comments on my music choices. Some good,
oh, really?
Some bad, yeah.
Some good, some bad?
Well, that's what you're going to get with music. That's not the only two CDs I got in my car. And for the people that are wondering, the other disc that you can barely see is the latest CD from Nick DiPaolo that was given to us recently. So that's his comedy CD in there.
We got the Ting Tings?
Huh?
You got Ting Tings in there?
Ah, you got the Ting Tings CD yesterday, my friend.
I was listening to that whole thing on the way home.
Yeah?
I'm such a fag.
You like everything about him?
There's probably... maybe two songs on there that I was kind of like, all right. Yeah. But the rest of them were like, wow, these are catchy goddamn songs.
Well, they had that other hit, too. What was the other hit?
Yeah, not as big as...
No, it did pretty well. Yeah, well, you're right. Huh? What was the other song by the Ting Tings?
Resident expert on gay music.
No, just I like good music.
He's got to make his little excuses. No, I like good music.
Shut up and let me go.
Yeah, shut up and let me go.
Hey! Damn, damn, damn. Yeah.
It's a great album.
I'm digging these goddamn stupid Ting Tings.
Which one are you doing? The name one?
No, this is Shut Up and Let Me Go.
Yeah.
It sounds very familiar right here.
This sounds very 80-ish.
Yes.
Yeah.
Bananarama-ish.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of the band this sounds like. Yeah, Bananarama.
Cool and the Gang.
Huh?
A little bit.
What does this sound like?
The Waitresses. She sounds snotty English.
And it's okay that you're admitting you like this, but you got to say it's a guilty pleasure.
Yes, it's a guilty pleasure. Like
most guys on the construction site are not cranking up the Ting Tang.
Like poppers and gay sex. Guilty pleasure.
What are you going to do? Some of this stuff is catchy.
It's so goddamn catchy. Hey.
Nothing wrong with it. They're like the biggest band in the UK.
Yeah, but the UK is a gay nation.
Yeah, but see, Travis, we're from two different generations. We're supposed to like guitar-driven
rock.
I hear guitar.
Guitar's in there.
That's like...
We have the same excuses.
No, that's swishy guitar, though, where they play like just like...
It's very catchy. And then there's just hotness in the way she sings. There's like this hotness in there.
I said MGMT is management. I'm a dummy. It's just M. What does it stand for, though?
It's short for management.
It is, right?
Yeah, okay, that's a great album, too.
Can I play Kids? A little piece of Kids for everybody?
Good one.
And you like this MGMT? We'll get back to your other song that you like.
Thank you.
We'll play everyone out with My Name. You got management, Kids? A little taste of this. Tell me if you like this.
All right.
This is a big hit on alternative rock stations.
Is it really?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, they just started playing it on alternation.
I think they're a local band, too, right?
They might be from Brooklyn. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I think they might be from the tri-state area. Trying to get to the vocals. What does this make you feel, Ann? Anything?
No, I'm not feeling this. Not like,
I like
hit me instantly.
I do like some of that poppy stuff, but I also like some of the dark stuff. This has kind of just that slightly dark feel to it. Just how it's put together.
Yeah.
Well, you know the other song they did.
Electric Eel?
With the heroin and all that.
Time to Pretend.
Yeah. Can I give you a little taste of Time to Pretend by the same band? Or
give it to me.
Or
dirty word in there.
Oh, no.
You won't find that.
Oh, boy.
When the tinklings
They're nice, clean, fun music.
Yes.
By the way, that song was in 21, yes. And I saw 21 recently. The movie was all right, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. This is what happens when you do music breaks. Awesome. Love it. This band rules. This effing sucks. This is awful.
Yeah, I know.
That's why it's hard to argue music taste. You know, people love what they love, man.
Like that. You don't know why you like it.
Right.
You hear it, something clicks. You're like, all right, I like that.
Yeah, it's no ting tings.
I don't like that. No.
Come on, Ant's a little bored. Give him his song.
What?
Give him his song.
That's not my name?
Yeah, give Ant his song. I want to see him bop a little
Stacey.
Bit.
Stacey. I'm so gay.
We're so lame, man.
I'm just so gay.
You're very straight. Just like me.
You know what? I justify some of the songs I listen to because I look down and I go, hey, it's an alternative rock channel.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's cool because it's on the alternative rock channel.
The channel it's on. It's a cool channel. They play all kinds of cool stuff.
Right.
You know, if you don't open your mind to like music.
It's not even that. It's not on one of those swishy channels. It's alternative rock, man.
Oh, you'll hear it on the swishy channel, too.
Oh, really? They put it on the pop channel?
Oh, yeah, they will.
And Maynard's got a new band?
Yeah.
I heard.
I'm not sure how you pronounce it, and if I pronounce it the wrong way, I might get.
Instead of Lucifer, they put a P instead of the L.
Pucifer?
Something like that.
I think that's how it's pronounced.
Maynard's a weird dude, though, man. But the song I heard yesterday was really. It got me. First play. I'm like, all right, I think I got to check out more of this.
Any band.
I don't want to say the band. Lucifer, replace the L with a P.
Any band he's in, it's going to be...
Pucifer?
That's just weird.
Pucifer. Pucifer.
You like Tool, Jimmy?
I do. I don't love them, but I got into them recently because I've heard a bunch of their stuff over the years. I wouldn't say I'm a fan.
Dude, Tool.
Tools.
And that other side... Perfect Circle.
Yeah. I do very much like the song...
What's great about Tool and Maynard? Like, most like bands, the lead singer's front and center... I went and saw a Tool show. I'm like, where's Maynard? He's in the back to the right.
singing from there for the whole show.
Didn't like stealing the spotlight.
For the entire show, and it just made you uncomfortable.
Yeah.
Because you're so used to having the guy out front.
It almost wouldn't be so bad, except the rest of their band really doesn't have a lot of stage presence.
Right.
And he's the only one that's kind of going nuts and doing things, but he's all the way in the back.
Yeah.
So you just get stuck with watching, you know, a couple of people, you know, like three people play music, and he's off in the back having a party somewhere.
Dude, it is so bizarre.
Although, there was a great show that I went to. It was actually tickets that you gave me, Ope. They were really good.
Was it the same day? Did we go to the same show?
No, you couldn't make it. I think you were out to dinner. But it was a really small show.
Were we sitting in the little balcony?
No, it was really nice tickets. They were like front row.
No, these balcony tickets I got too were good. Okay. Yeah, I was bummed I couldn't go with you.
That was a great show, man.
I love Tool. Really love everything this guy does.
Certain great bands would have the lead singer on the right-hand side, like from the audience stage right. A lot of bands would put him in the center, but a lot of other bands would have a bassist, a lead guitarist, and then the singer all the way to the right.
Like who? Sabbath? Sabbath did it that way?
Days. He sure did.
But this
Ozzy wasn't in the back, but he was.
No, Maynard. I mean, if he could, he would sing off stage at the concert I saw. I'm sure he changes it up as they move on. Give Anthony a song. He's out of the conversation.
He's out. Way before they got big.
Yeah,
yeah. He introduced me to them.
He's
really.
Yeah, he was playing them before the iTunes commercial.
He is the best rock jock.
Absolutely.
That's not my name.
That's not my name.
It's the same freaking song.
It's the same song.
This is Tony Basil, obviously. Who was an old broad when this song hit.
Oh, I know.
She tried to make believe she was a kid, but she was floating around the music business for a very long time.
Remember that video with that pig cheerleader they had in it?
Yeah.
You know she was the bottom of the pyramid.
Holding up the whole pyramid.
Just a mess.
It's the same song, no? Just twist it around a little bit?
Yeah, a little, you know. It's an 80s version.
And look, to all the people in shock, you got your guilty pleasures, too. Shut up.
Absolutely. Shut your mouth.
Or at least brave enough to say, all right, hey, the Ting Tangs, that song, kind of like it.
Nothing guilty about that.
I know this is not going to make me look like the cool shock jock, but what the hell.
You know, it was really, really a great douchey moment.
Huh.
I was watching The Terminator the other day, the original.
Sure.
And when she's in that club...
Right.
And what was it called?
Tech Noir.
Right. When she's in Tech Noir, sitting at that very inconvenient, you can't put anything on this table.
Right.
Because it's just like a grate. And when the Terminator's walking his way through in slow motion, there are guys dancing. And it is so incredibly bad. They are doing the 80s, little 80s dance with their thin ties and everything. Oh, when they start getting shot, I'm just cheering.
That would have been a perfect place for Harvey Milk to do some of his recruiting, I'm thinking.
Recruit you. I'm here to recruit you.
It's fantastic.
There you go. Anthony, they're starting to look at that old picture that I put up. Wow, who was Ant's hair plugger back in the day of that photo?
They did
a great job.
That's no plugs. They weren't even follicles. They were my own follicles from the top of my head. I was burning the hair candle at both ends, I guess. And, you know, the candle that burns twice as bright burns half as long.
You had an impressive afro. We laugh at Sam's afro, but yours was just as big when I met you.
I would have won Afro Wars, hands down.
Right.
Here's the club noir scene.
Oh, wow.
She sits at the stupid table, Sarah Connor. And then the guy
in the background,
in the background
behind her is even awful.
It is every white guy dance that's going on. It's fantastic.
He's walking in past the
gate. Looking for Sarah Connor.
That was the governor of California. That's so weird.
Yeah.
And then he just breaks that guy's hand.
What did he get, sir? He got all his weightlifting buddies to play a little part here and there.
Yeah, you know, gets a strong guy. He's walking through Tech Noir, which is just a great 80s place.
Look at the girl behind Sarah Connor dance. There are some really
awful dancing
dances
going on. And then the little slow-mo shot of some of these guys. It's so bad. There, now we're going slow motion. Look at that dancing that's going down. Woo! That says 80s. Yeah. That is 80s written all over it. Gay. Gaties.
Wow, she's got the Aussie hair, though.
That's a great... She should be shooting Shot in the Dark video.
The Aussie Shot in the Dark hair. the Ting Tings are from Denmark, Anthony.
Denmark?
Yeah, getting that.
Well, what are they doing with that limey accent?
I guess they kind of have that... sound down. I don't know.
Where's that? There's a girl doing an 80s dance, and then there's one guy that gets really nice, yeah, camera time. there he is.
Oh, the thin tie guy?
Look at him. You get to see him again. Yeah, he's doing the 80s dance.
He has a white suit jacket and a white thin, like, piano keys tie.
Thin tie. You just want that white jacket covered in his own blood.
God, thank God I grew up in the 90s. Didn't have to deal with that 80s crap.
And then I was also laughing at how outdated his laser sight is. It's as long as the gun. Look at his laser sight.
Do you have that gun, Ant?
Oh, no, I got better guns than that.
Schwarzenegger just stands over Sarah Connor and pulls the gun out and just lasers her right in the forehead. He is really ready to give her a shooting.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But Michael Bane knows how to take care of him if you're blessed with the shotgun. That movie's always fun to watch every so often.
Yeah.
So this is a great... The original Terminator is a good movie.
Yeah, man. The music will drive you nuts, though. It's just a synthesizer going crazy. Like someone just put it on
autopilot or something.
When they're running.
Everyone's screaming audio. This is one of the greatest scenes in history.
Yeah, it is a good one.
Let's say hi to Brian.
Shooting and bad 80s music.
Brian in Pennsylvania. Brian.
Hey, what's going on, fellas?
Hey, man.
Hey, I got an example of a song that is kind of stupid, but I love it. It's called Paper Planes. I think it's M.I.A. or Maya. I'm not sure.
Of course it's M.I.A.
Oh, everyone remembers Paper Planes.
Did she end up performing that at the Grammys pregnant?
Yes.
She was 9 months pregnant at the Grammys. She must have had the kid by now. No. She still hasn't had the kid? She shows up at the Grammys 9 months pregnant. Her due date was pretty much this past Sunday during the Grammys. And she did the song? I didn't stay up for it.
She started with the song. She did about 10 seconds of it. And then they did that combo of Jay-Z, Kanye West, and a couple other rappers.
Whatever. Yeah, this song Brian likes. I like this one, too.
You gotta be careful with this one.
Yeah, no, it's okay.
Oh, really?
You gotta be careful.
There's another freaking...
You got the radio edit?
I think I took the best of the lyrics.
Oh, I like this, too.
Thank you.
What was coming up there, Eric?
It was getting close.
To the F word?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is that a new song?
That's been out a while now.
No, it came out last year or two
but
years
I mean, it's within the last couple. That's when it was in Slumdog.
No.
Yeah. They used it in Slumdog.
Pineapple
yeah.
Express, too. Yeah,
that's where it was. That was also in Slumdog.
Okay. Exactly. Jeez. What's wrong with you?
What's up with everybody?
How do you not know that?
What's going on?
How did you not know
that? Yeah, having a good time.
Ooh, you're out. With a good one.
What's up, man?
Did he?
Yeah.
What did he say?
He said, how did you not know that?
Got
That's
him.
A damn good point.
We gotta,
I don't know. Apologize.
Kellen is not happy with you, Anthony.
What?
Kellen.
I'm sorry.
Kellen, go. Kellen, we got to hit a break here, but go.
Hey.
Dude, you're a guy?
Yeah.
Your argument is shot right there. You're Kelly and Helen. You got two girl names, and you're trying to say stop calling us gay?
Kelly and Helen.
You're
Why
Kellen.
Was that named after Kellen Winslow, the football player?
Oh, really?
Well, what, football like European football, which we call soccer?
No, Winslow played in it.
Oh, I have no
Kelly
idea.
Kelly and Helen.
Kelly and Helen. All right.
I was just wondering how you can call us gay when we have got the best sports fans in the world. What do your sports fans do after they've gone to see their matches and their games?
Well,
you know what, Kellen? You're going to argue the soccer thing with us?
Yeah.
Well, we got guys that go to any country and kick the hell out of each other.
All right, Suze Mary.
All right, Kellen, you're not gay. Let's just...
All right, it's not a whole
let's
gay
Let's cut our
nation.
Losses. Yeah, we're just, you know, having a little fun here.
Let's just the guys are a little effeminate, that's all I'm saying.
You never called your friends growing up the F word for gay just because you could?
And apparently they're from Denmark. What do I know?
Yeah, it was, you know, it doesn't mean you're actually, you know... Blah, blah.
I won't deny that a lot of the gay guys here are over-the-top gay. Absolutely. I used to work with a lot of gay guys, and the filth that would come out of their mouth was obscene.
All right, sir.
I feel like I'm watching The Office, the English version of Office, talking to this guy. Fantastic.
Isn't it wonderful?
Yeah. He got it.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Have you guys seen a picture of the girl from the Ting Ting? Have you seen a picture of her?
Yeah, well, I wasn't sure if she was hot or not.
She's a little ridden hard and put up wet, but...
I think because of
bad.
I think how they cut the video, a lot of quick cuts. That means they're trying to cover up some stuff.
Yeah,
that's what I.
If
think.
You check out a picture of her, she's considered hot in England. I know people in America think girls in England are ugly and have bad teeth, but she's like the antithesis of hotness at the
moment.
We got
much hotter girls here in America, my friend.
Yeah,
I know. I've seen
much hotter. Much hotter. All right, Kim.
Yeah.
You know what seems Thanks. To have girls that aren't very attractive? A country, Australia. Now I hear they're goers. I hear the goers, but whenever I go to these Australian, like, websites.
Porn sites. You're going to a regular Australian website? Or you?
And, like, Australian amateurs and things like that. I'm not saying 100%, but a lot of them just have this weird thing going on. Mm. I don't know.
Some of that inbreeding they did back when they started.
When they first got over there as the criminal nation.
Yeah, they didn't have enough people to mix it up, I'm thinking.
Yeah.
I've heard there's really hot shit. I know a lot of comedians have gone over there to work. I've heard the girls there are fantastic.
I heard they're goers. Like, that. You can absolutely get laid down under. Down under.
Mm.
But, you know.
Well, let's try to find a hot Australian babe today.
I'm sure you'll find one. You know.
But there's something a little, like, off about them.
Yeah.
Just a little bit, right?
Something off of them, like Olivia Newton-John.
I want to go down to Australia and then just do nothing but hack, like, Australian references. Hey, Australia, do you get a bunch of shrimps on the barbie for me?
Oh, they'd laugh and love you. All the girls would be clamoring over you. Oh, yeah.
Just really corny stuff. Kangaroo jokes.
Wallabies.
We got a break. Stunt Brain, do this going into break. Or the people just sat through our music break here. We got some Dennis Leary tickets?
Yeah, the Rescue Me Comedy Tour is April 2nd at Radio City Music Hall. Yep. Dennis Leary, Adam Ferrara, Lenny Clark, and, of course, the season premiere. The on-sale date is Monday, but we've got some tickets to give away.
For New York, right?
Yes.
How many do you want to give away?
You can give away a couple pair here.
Yeah, let's do a couple pairs. Make sure you could be in New York because we're an international show. We just took a call from England, so... Make sure you can...
April 2nd, Radio City.
Make sure you're going to be in New York or you're from New York, whatever. April 2nd is the date. Okay. 877-212-ONA to get those tickets. We'll continue. Opie and Anthony.
Yeah.
Now we're talking.
Look, I'm dancing. Feeling the Terminator dance. I'm at Club Tech Noir.
This is awful.
Isn't it?
Anthony and I were just discussing... This reminds us that, like, back... God, I guess you got to go back almost 15, 20 years. No one wanted their music in movies.
No.
So you would always get this weird, obscure band... Or Hollywood would just get some musicians together and go, well, we need a rock song here.
Yeah.
And now, man, you know, you're praying that your music gets into movies.
That's in a movie. Hell yeah.
It was like such the no-no for the longest time. They didn't understand that how that would be good for their band.
No.
From a marketing standpoint.
This scene where he's walking through in slow motion, even though the dancing is horrible.
Yeah.
It was just, it's a great movie, man.
Yeah, he's very ominous.
Schwarzenegger, I think he's the best action hero ever.
He was really good in Terminator.
Yeah. They should just take this song out and put a newer song in.
He's still got Dummy doing that dance with his white jacket and thin tie.
That guy's the greatest.
Oh, the best.
You still think Australian women suck?
Why, who is that, Kylie Minogue or something?
No. That's a good one right there. Maybe we can put that up on onaradio.com. There's no nudity there, Stunt Brain.
Look.
He's a fresh face.
I'm saying everybody. You go to some of these amateur sites, and they show Aussie girls. You know, that's like Aussie model.
Yeah.
You see just a regular Australian girl.
Well, Steve from Jersey writes, Australian women, have skin like leather wallets. Is that the problem?
That could be a problem.
They're out in the sun a little too much?
They're out in the sun a
lot. Is that Kylie? Kylie Minogue has the nicest hiney. That might be an older shot, though. She's getting up there now.
She's no kid.
But she has a nice hiney. Look at that hiney.
She was doing the little locomotion song.
Yeah.
Do the locomotion.
All right, we're going to move on. We're
Kim Wilde with her big, big, beefy lips.
Ooh,
back
what?
In the 80s. Remember her? Where the Kids in America.
Where the Kids in America. Whoa.
But I think she was English.
Yeah. We were talking about the plane crash earlier.
You want to give me a power boot on this computer? Just like
what happened?
Like smash it.
What happened?
Just hit the off button and then turn it back on, and I'll deal with it. Because everything's frozen on my computer. It's very distracting.
Yeah.
Oh, is that my computer? No wonder. Look at this thing.
What's
holy mother? What is it? An Innova? Lenovo? What is this? What is it even called?
This was
that's
Lenovo,
your
the Chinese IBM computer.
Yeah, but when did they stop making those?
No, these are new.
Is that new?
New?
Yeah, well, new is 2009.
It's a little too big looking to be new.
That's crap. Yeah, just hold that down and let's restart.
All right.
All right. There you go. Thank you, sir. God, I didn't even know. I thought that was just sitting there.
Yeah, I thought that was an old VCR or something.
Yeah, that's what it looks like, an old friggin' VCR.
From my angle, yeah. It's definitely an old VCR. Anyway, the big news is the plane crash.
You got me right. What?
The big news is that plane crash. 49 dead, 48 were on the flight, one on the ground.
Ow.
Do we have more info coming in? The boys are working in the office. When we get something new, we'll certainly bring it to you.
Well, there's one starting up right now.
Oh, great.
Isn't that grounded?
They're taking
That's wonderful. Imagine you're on the same plane this morning.
What are the odds?
Newark.
Yeah, probably.
What are the odds? Safest flight around.
As long as you're going to a different plane.
Maybe you're going
plane.
To somewhere
not the same
warm.
Make and model that just went down in Buffalo.
No,
last
same
night.
Make and model to Buffalo right now. I'd sit on the wing of that plane right now. There's no way you're going to have problems today.
I don't think that's ever happened. That's the old lightning strike in twice.
I'm a big fan of flying the day after a plane crash, knowing that the odds are just ridiculous, but to be on the same plane that just crashed, that would make me a bit nervous.
Yeah.
Yeah, why not? What if it's some kind of some what's problem that they all have?
That only happens when it's going to Buffalo?
Yeah. Wow. And they wouldn't have it happen 2 days in a row. Like, even DC-10s, who had a weird design flaw, wouldn't.
Hate those.
I do, too. They're terrible-looking, unstable-looking planes.
How about today's the day it does happen and then really freaks us all out?
Yeah.
Two in 2 days, imagine.
So odd seeing that huge Continental logo with the wreckage around it, isn't it, Jimmy?
Continental has been, I still say that I'm still extremely comfortable on Continental because
they also had the one that went off the runway into the.
They did. They had that, and then they had this, and they were also the piece that fell off when the Concorde was taking off. It was a piece of a Continental plane that came off, and then the Concorde ripped up its tire
burst.
I'll
tell you where Continental is really bad. Apparently driving around on the taxiways because they're constantly clipping each other's wings
and
hitting each other like just a slow little bump by the terminal.
Look, man, when you have to squeeze through two cars to go down some of these side roads here in New York, it's a little shaky. Imagine being in a plane and trying to figure out if you got enough room.
That gets me, though, when this is a little car and he's driving real slow between two like trucks. And I'm whipping through at 40.
Oh, dude.
Pulling my mirrors in automatically make it.
That's why I'm so bummed I got a new car. Because, you got the crappy car. Yeah, you pull those mirrors in and you just go.
You got the automatic mirror thing?
You're threading a needle.
You got the automatic mirrors where they...
I'm not sure. I haven't read everything yet.
So you don't got to lean over and pull the mirror in?
Yeah, I push the button and it goes...
Handy?
Closes.
Oh, is that handy?
It's wonderful.
Squeeze right through.
Sometimes I close my mirrors while I'm driving just to show the chicks I can.
That you don't even need to know what's behind or outside of you.
Who gives a turkey, ladies? Get in. You're after smoking the vent.
Hey, the guy that got dragged for 20 miles, we got an update on that story.
Yes.
Man, I was thinking about that all day yesterday. What are the odds that you're going to be dragged for 20 miles? I think you heard the story by now. The guy gets hit. The guy that hit him stops, right?
Yep.
Kind of pulls over, does the right thing. And as he kind of goes back to see what's going on with the guy, another car comes along and somehow the guy gets underneath the van and is dragged for 20 miles.
Yeah.
And then the guy that initially hit him, I think, was thinking, well, he must be okay because I don't see him anymore.
I don't see him.
So he jumped back in his car and went on his merry way. And it turns out this other van, dragged him for 20 miles, smearing blood all over the highways in the tri-state area.
Oh, just a mess.
And they've identified this person, right?
They identified him. Yes, they did.
That's going to be, what, nice little twist to how they identified him?
Yes, because he had no wallet on him, no ID.
Right. All right, let's find out.
Police have finally identified the man dragged under a van for miles across Queens and Brooklyn.
The victim's sister and cousins were in disbelief over what happened.
Oh my God, everybody.
Can I ask a question?
Crying,
why is he talking like that?
Because they're in disbelief.
Is that Pablo?
That's Slattery.
Oh, Slattery. John, you're right. Slattery. You're right. You're right. You're right.
Holy mackerel.
Slattery.
Oh, my God. Everyone is crying. Everybody is going crazy. In especially over there in my country, everybody is going crazy.
In my country.
The man dragged was 26-year-old Guido Carabajo Jara, who moved here from Ecuador.
Oh, what a... Wow. How does that work out? His last name is Horror.
Oh, wow.
And he dies in a
quite
horror.
A horror.
Jeez. Isn't it weird when that crap works out with these stories?
Yeah.
Last name's Hara.
The man dragged was 26-year-old Guido Carabajo Jara, who moved here from Ecuador, was working as a tile man and sending money home to his wife and 4-year-old daughter.
Police explained that the man was face up when the second vehicle ran over him, with his sternum being fish-hooked by a steel plate under the van known as a skid plate.
Oh, my God.
It got his breastbone.
But at least that tells you that he probably died immediately. If he wasn't dead, there's no way you're living with your breastbone hooked under a...
Hooked.
You could live a little bit. Why not?
I don't know. That's...
Dude, that's...
Your heart.
It probably... It doesn't just slide under neatly. I'm sure that rips up your innards and your heart. If it's bad enough to drag you for 20 miles, it doesn't gingerly slide in.
Yeah, yeah. That was dragging him over bumpy roads and everything. He was pretty much hooked on that thing, I'd say.
What's the clearance in a vehicle like that?
Your clearance.
Can you almost make it, you think?
No.
In that situation, you're going to get hooked every time?
No, I don't think you'd make it. That's low clearance.
Low clearance?
It's going to hit you. Ugh. You think you'd make it all the way through, and that big, fat van differential just takes your friggin' face off.
How distracted are you by your reggaeton? The drag guy for 20 miles.
Wow.
Steel plate under the van known as a skid plate.
The body was dragged over highways in Queens and Brooklyn, nearly 20 miles.
Myself, I say, how would that happen?
After the 50-minute trek, the body was so battered that clothing and flesh were worn off from the friction of the road.
I saw the body, I saw his face, and I cannot believe it. I mean, until I saw his face, I didn't believe it.
The victim was killed the day after his 26th birthday. He will be buried in Ecuador.
Oh.
God damn.
And in 3 boroughs, apparently.
Yeah.
Wow.
And they identified him. Did they say it? They don't mention the iPhone?
No, it was from his iPhone. Now, look at that. He's got an iPhone on him. He's dragged 20 miles, dies, yet his iPhone still working. How about that endorsement for the iPhone?
Was the iPhone working, or did they have to go into the computer mechanism of it? And
I'm sure they pulled it out of his pocket, turned it on, got a signal, called up someone on their favorites on the little directory. Hi, do you know this man?
Maybe they just pulled the little card out and then said, this is the number on the little card. Who is this?
Maybe, but I like to think that the iPhone was fine.
Okay.
I'm a big fan of the iPhone, Jimmy.
I know you are.
Or not.
Not according to this report, actually. It says that...
Oh, boy.
From the memory inside the victim's damaged iPhone, police were able to track that.
Oh, boy.
Damn it.
You can't blame the phone.
Wow, you can't? Being dragged 20 miles?
Yeah, over rocky road. Can't blame the phone.
Oh.
That's a sick story.
What a sick damn story.
All right, we got to play a little catch-up. It's Black History Month. Who are we looking at today?
Who?
To celebrate Black History Month, the Opie and Anthony Show is recognizing those historic African Americans without whom this country would not be the melting pot it is today. Today we celebrate Jamie Foxworth, known best for her work as Judy Winslow on the sitcom Family Matters, playing the Winslows' youngest until being written off in 1993. In 2000, with an empty bank account and a full-blown drug habit, Judy took her career in a new direction, adopting the moniker Crave, and landed roles in such epics as My Baby Got Back 29 and Booty Talk 20 Superfine Sisters.
Oh, yeah.
For her original career choices and desire to stay relevant, Jamie continues to be an inspiration for all aspiring actresses. Oh. Stay tuned for more icons of Black history on the Opie and Anthony Show.
Opie and Anthony. We're going to get
give away more Dennis Leary tickets in a little bit here. Tickets go on sale, what, April 2nd? I mean, for the April 2nd show on Monday?
Yeah, the show is April 2nd. They go on sale Monday, and he's got some special deal that benefits the firefighters, that Leary Firefighter Fund. Kind of a cool charity.
Very cool.
April 2nd, what did I think we give that? It's Saturday, right?
I want to say hi to Philip.
Philip?
Just graduated from the police academy. He's been on the job a month and a half. Related to my family through marriage and stuff.
Yeah.
And I had dinner with him and his lovely, lovely sister.
NYPD?
At F.H. Riley's. Yeah, he does the Times Square thing. He said that he's just a young kid, just getting into it. His dad was like a 20, 25-year veteran, did narcotics, like hardcore stuff. And his son's now on the job. And he goes, yeah, my whole job is I walk around Times Square taking knives away from gang members and stuff and taking hundreds of pictures every weekend. All the tourists, they just love taking pictures with the cops when they come to town.
Yeah, NYPD, they're like celebrities to the out-of-towners.
Yeah, so.
Because they're in a lot of movies, you know?
Yep.
Not the real cops, but a lot of people play NYPD on TV. So you want pictures with them.
They're all looking for Dennis Franz.
Yeah, Dennis Franz.
And his butt. Remember when that was a big controversy? Wow.
They're going to show his ass in the shower.
Lucky us.
Wow.
Lucky us.
And side boob they showed. Some girl's side boob.
Yeah, you know, they knew how to get people talking, right?
God, I remember all the controversies that would pop up years ago. The condom ad, that was a biggie. A bra ad where they finally showed the brassiere on a woman. That was a huge controversy for television.
Really?
Yeah, because they used to just have women hold up a bra. Or they would show the bra as if it was on an invisible woman. And it's like spinning around. The Playtex bra lifts and separates. And that was on TV. You know. And then finally they had a woman wearing a bra.
They finally filled it up.
Hey, look at my aren't they great in this bra? And now you see Victoria's Secret's models in their panties and bras, and
like
it is
nothing.
It is spank central.
Oh yeah,
like
they just didn't know how to make the bra.
They
back,
were like
back in the 50s
black
and the 40s.
Jackets.
Look at it, horrible.
You want your boobs to look like silos? They're just big, pointy, nasty things.
God.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Well, who thought the pointy breast was attractive? Hubba hubba.
Afraid of any poke throughs. They made them really thick because they didn't want anything
Showing through.
Yeah, poking through.
That would be girl crazy. Showed through. Maybe it was chilly out. Look at that.
They were going for that natural cone look.
And the natural cone look, that could be the most unnatural thing ever. And the bra went from like their neck to their belly. Just this hardcore material, 18 clasps in the back. Look at that point.
Who would wear that?
What is that thing?
It's like a, how do you explain that?
Weapon.
They're two cones. It's like the.
But with the point.
The nose cone of a rocket.
The dress point.
It's like two V2s on her chest.
Looks like a pyramid if you tilt your head sideways.
And the torso looks like mine. It's a very average-looking physique.
You know what? I didn't want to know more about that picture, but I'm suspicious that it might be a guy wearing that bra.
Yeah, I was suspicious of that, too.
And I didn't want to know any more, but now Jimmy's saying it, so.
Is that a guy wearing a bra?
I don't know. It could go, probably. I don't know.
I don't know. With that pointy bra thing, you could put a lot of fat meat in there and make it look like you got cleavage.
All right. Hey, Ed, you know a thing or two about home invasions, right?
Well, I don't know anything about them. I've never been part of one, but I sure am prepared for one.
And you know what? With you cranking your ting-tings in your house, that might that might make people think they got an easy target.
Oh, please. Oh, please. Don't he tasks me. Keith actually came over the house this morning to drag the garbage out. You know.
Oh, that's nice of him.
Take out the trash. And he texts me. He goes, I'll be taking the garbage out. He goes, so please identify your target before you shoot. I go, I was like, don't worry. I'll just wing you. I go, worst case scenario, I just wing you. He goes, okay, please, 9mm or smaller. He's already knows that at some point I'll probably shoot him.
What does wing you mean?
Just kind of nick you.
Oh.
A little wing you. But he, yeah. So he was out there this morning.
Nice. Well, we had another home invasion overnight.
Jam it.
And I like playing these for you because you're...
What happened?
You're more than prepared for this type of thing.
Armed citizen.
I don't know.
Thwarted the crime. Killing the home invader.
I don't know. I don't like to know the outcome ahead of time on these. We'll find out together.
Let's learn.
A man is alerted of an impending home invasion by his security cameras. He arms himself and actually shoots and drives away the intruders.
Wow.
Here's how things went down.
See, he's laughing because it worked out nice.
Did you know that, Ant? Did you heard the story?
No, I didn't.
Oh, wow.
I thought it was going to be, you know, the phone cord around the neck. And watching his wife being sodomized.
Just out of reach of that gun.
Yep.
You know it's in that drawer. Oof. And you're like, oh, look how close I am.
See, this guy's got cameras, scanners.
Yep. It was the Diaz brothers coming.
Yeah, Diaz brothers were coming for him.
Intruders. Here's how things went down. Four armed suspects attempted to break into his house.
Four.
When he shot right at the suspects. He even put a bullet through the windshield of the suspect's car. The four men got scared and took off. All of them remain on the run.
Well, the guy's like in wait till you hear this. He even put a bullet through their windshield.
Bullet through the windshield.
Of course.
I don't think I'd go to that extent. You know.
Why? Because then
questionable.
Then the authorities like, now you're in trouble.
They were trying to leave.
I don't understand that whole now you're in trouble when you were just minding your own business.
Depends on where you are.
You didn't wake up that morning thinking I was going to shoot my gun. Someone has invaded your space and now you're supposed to understand exactly what you can and can't do. I say screw that.
When they back off and the initial danger is gone, you're not allowed anymore.
But that's not fair.
Weird.
You were put in that situation.
Yeah.
A situation you don't want to be in.
Right.
A high-pressure situation.
That guy's probably going to say something like, well, I stepped out, or, you know, I saw the car, and I saw what I believed to be a gun coming out of the window aiming at me and, you know, took a few shots.
See, that to me is a guy, even though they're outside the house, who's justified. Like, we had that argument at the time about...
I'm going out. I'm going to shoot that.
Yeah, the guy who shot the two unarmed people break into his neighbor's house, and he shot them as they were running away.
Yeah.
But this guy, if four guys are trying to break into your house, I don't care if you follow them to 7-Eleven 8 miles away and blast them. You're justified. You're justified in killing them.
Yeah.
Partially.
Dude, the video is awesome. Can we link this?
Oh, my God.
Nice.
This guy's got some good security cameras, man.
Jesus.
Damn.
Holy crap. This isn't one of those goofy 7-Eleven cams.
I want this camera.
This is like high-def security camera footage. We'll link it on onaradio.com.
That's got all kinds of angles.
Middle of the afternoon,
pulls up.
It's like a three-camera shoot. Look.
Here comes some guys. They're running toward the house.
Guns drawn. They mean business. Next thing you know, they're running back to the car.
Oh,
that guy slipped.
Feet don't fail me now. They're trying to get back into their car.
One guy's trying to get his car back.
And a few shots right through the windshield. Bye-bye.
Wow, that guy changed his tune real fast.
Middle of the afternoon.
Yep. Oh, yeah, that is like
look at
noon.
That. Something's going on, though.
Four black dudes running up. You wonder if he was if that was a lot of times drug dealers.
Yeah, I'm thinking this guy might be a little suspect in his business dealings if he's got that kind of security.
Right.
And he's ready like that in broad daylight to thwart four guys running to his house.
Yep. Pretty amazing.
So who knows?
It's on a site we
we'll get it up.
That a site that likes to get us in trouble. Breitbart. Stupid Breitbart.
It's on a bunch of different sites, so
yeah.
You know, if you Google,
all right.
if you Google News,
Google,
you know,
yeah, go
Tucson home invasion, you'll find it.
Go everywhere else except that website I just mentioned, if you can.
Nice.
And we'll link it to onaradio.com. It should be linked in a matter of minutes. Let's go to Ronnie. Very upset with us, Ronnie.
How you doing?
Pretty good. What's up, Ronnie?
Well, I was just, you know, I was listening all the way in this morning, and you guys were making fun of what I certainly took making fun of the air disaster today, you know, saying, I wonder if this pilot thought he was going to be another Sully, and what am I going to do first? Am I going to do Letterman, or am I going to do Leno? And
really making light of the situation, you know, poking
Frunkus?
Fun.
Frunkus?
I want to know what was going on.
Frunkus? Frunkus?
Honestly, we were lightening up the story a little bit, but we certainly took it very seriously, my friend.
Now, the point was, sir, that the pilot going down, since Sully has become like this celebrity, so the point was that any pilot in any kind of trouble right now, the first instinct is going to be, oh, I'm going to be a celebrity too because of what happened with him. I don't think that's a big, it's making humor out of an awful situation, but I don't think that's a big stretch to think that a person's mind would work that way.
Jimmy's absolutely right. It's more a commentary on the media and the way they've handled the Sully incident, having him all over the place and a hero and doing press conferences, that any pilot that gets into trouble these days is going to think, hey, I'm going to be the next Sully. Let me think about a book, appearances, things like that. And, you know,
I think we took it
doesn't work out that way.
Ronnie, I think we took it very seriously. Well, I really do. I mean, we said how much it sucks. And then we also said, like, we're just still living off the moment that we had with this Sully guy. And now, you know, life kicks you in the teeth and goes, well, enough with that. This is the cold, hard reality.
Here's some reality. Sometimes
that these plane crashes do kill everybody.
They fall out of the sky and everyone dies.
It sucks.
People on the ground.
Ronnie, I'm sitting here wondering if I know anybody. I know a lot of people in Western New York. So a lot of people in Buffalo. I'm keeping my fingers crossed this morning.
So what's the problem, Ronnie? You got some objections? Is that what it is?
Well, you know, I mean, you know, I don't listen to you guys, to be perfectly honest. I just happen to hit the thing, so I'm not familiar with
it. Wait, Ronnie. Right. We hate when people say
he's got
that.
All the features.
But,
this
he's got,
guy.
But yet he's got the number.
Yeah, Ronnie.
No, I'm just saying I'm not familiar
Ronnie,
with
I,
humor.
Ronnie, okay, I'm kind of with you so far. I don't even really mind that you were a little offended this morning, but you're trying to say that you just happened to hit our station today?
This is what I actually did. You know, I'm listening to this the fan on the way in, and Boomer's partner was driving me crazy, so I just hit the button. That
oh,
goes,
he's
hey,
such
I'm
an outrageous
FM.
Car, that guy.
Yeah, I can't stand him. Now, anyway, you guys just happened to be there, right? So boom, all of a sudden your station came on, and I wasn't even aware that there was a plane crash. So all of a sudden I'm hearing you guys do this little skit, and, you know, I'm like, well, that's a little insensitive, because I don't even know there's a plane crash yet. So then I hit another station and I hear there's a plane crash and I'm like, oh my god, these guys certain they were talking about an actual plane crash that just happened. And I was amazed by the insensitivity at which I perceived that you handled this situation.
You know what, Ronnie,
why would you care? Like, I don't understand. Like, I don't comprehend as an American, as somebody who listens to the radio and watches TV like you do, why would you be concerned with the attitude of other adults when it has nothing to do with you? I don't understand why that would affect you in any way, shape, or form. I don't comprehend that.
You can't understand why 49 people are dead, and I just perceive two guys making light, making fun of the situation, parodying the situation. You don't understand how, as a normal human being, I would find that so offensive.
No, I don't, and I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. Because there's been plenty of things that have been made fun of that I don't find offensive, and I want to know: are you offended by the fact that Stephen King, as an artist or whatever, writes about children being murdered? Like, I don't look at things that way. So why is it that with humor, people have this asterisk they put next to it with what's appropriate, and yet if somebody wrote a song about it, you'd be like, wow, that's really good that artist expressed themselves like that. Or if they wrote a story about it, you'd be like, wow, that's really good that artist expressed themselves like that. But if people are addressing something awful in humor, all of a sudden, you're violated and offended.
Stephen King's a fiction writer. This is something, these bodies are still burning, and you guys are making fun of it.
Don't say it like that.
Good point, Ronnie. Good point. You got Jimmy good there.
Yeah, you really did. But a fiction writer is still capitalizing on something that does happen.
Of course he is.
Okay, so what?
But this is a real life situation.
It's real life, Jimmy.
Jimmy.
Don't you understand that?
You're wondering if some of your friends.
Turnabout's fair play.
Yep.
Right. How about the
Ronnie? I got to say, you've turned two out of three of us around.
Right. The third one you're working on pretty well here. You're convincing me. How about the song angle then, Ronnie? Or how about the story angle? If you want to hide behind Stephen King writes fiction, how about the song angle or the story angle or like writing a book about it?
Writing a book about it's fine. Why not?
Why is that okay?
You're not making fun of
tragedy. Okay, what I'm saying is, why is it with humor that's the place that people choose their self-righteous indignation?
Tell them why, Ronnie. You know.
We all know.
Bad, Ronnie.
Help me out on this one.
We're with you, Ronnie, but you got it.
My self-righteous indignation.
Because he's making light.
I don't like that they made fun of that. I, as a person, have never concerned myself or been violated or offended by what other people were making fun of. I've never in my life been bothered by that.
Because when you write a book or something, you're reporting on the facts. In humor and comedy, you are just making light of a tragedy, and people have perished, families are upset, and you're going on just making jokes about it. I too was offended,
but Mike,
as that was happening,
I know you were. I saw it on your face and heard it in your impression of the thing and the pointing out that it was Lone Pilot. You were offended, but what I'm saying is, if you write a book like about serial killers, say, and even though you're just documenting what happened, you are directly profiting from the photos of murder victims. So I want to know, those are real things that happened, and I would like to know how many publishing houses you've called when you've seen books on the shelves and said, how are they directly profiting from the photos of these murdered people?
Buddy, you are completely out of your mind.
No, I'm really not.
No, you really are.
No, I'm not.
So you talk about making a giant leap from point A to point Z. Incredible.
How is that a big? Well, how is that a big leap?
They crashed at X.
Oh, because you go all the way to Z, Jimmy.
With the way that people, an artist or whatever, or a performer addresses something that happened that is real and that is tragic. Why do you have a different set of standards for humor that you do for songwriters or authors? That's not a big leap at all.
One is chronicling an event that happened. The other one is making fun of an event that is happening in front of our eyes right now, where you've got family members and you've got friends sitting by the radio and the television looking, saying, oh my God, I hope I don't know anybody on this flight. And all of a sudden, somebody's making fun of it.
So if you're chronicling...
Good point, Ronnie.
So if you're chronicling... the murder victims through photos and stuff like that, and making a profit of it, that's acceptable. But addressing it in humor is not.
Uh-oh, Ronnie, he might have you there.
He doesn't have me. It's ridiculous.
Ronnie, my whole career...
nothing to do with the other.
Ronnie, of course...
talking apples and oranges. Jimmy's talking apples and oranges.
Are we supposed to chronicle nothing in history that ever happened?
Well, exactly. Of course not. Exactly.
That's what we do. We compile facts.
What you're saying is this, Ronnie. I've dealt with guys like you my whole career. Guys, if you hear something... they get offended at it, and you have to justify why it was wrong for people to address it in humor. Yet if it was a subject that wasn't offending you, you'd be telling somebody, oh, come on, lighten up, it was just a joke. Most things you make fun of have somebody that's going to be bothered by it. Not all things, but most things.
Next thing you know, someone on this show will be making Hitler jokes. And then,
exactly.
And then that's when I walk.
That would be crazy.
I completely agree with what you said.
Ronnie, you speak our language, trust me.
That just about... every human being would be offended by what you said today, making fun of an air accident that so far 49 people have died. Yeah. And you don't think that there's anything wrong completely?
I
want to
know how it was made fun of.
Yeah, and by the way,
how it was made fun of, the actual accident.
Yeah.
The actual accident, you're actually saying that as the plane is going down, the pilot, instead of thinking about how the heck am I going to save...
A hypothetical fake pilot.
You're saying, wow, here's my chance for fame. I could be another Sully. Gee, am I going to do Letterman first, or should it be Leno?
Isn't that a commentary more on the way they put Sully on every single show, and you've been seeing him on the news, than it is us making fun or making light of the death of people in an air crash? Did we actually sit here and make light of the fact that people died? We could have made jokes like that. Mm-hmm. We didn't.
Well,
we made jokes about...
that would have been really sick had you... We were so good.
We were only partially sick.
Ronnie, you got another example of us making light and making a joke out of the tragedy that happened up there in Buffalo?
No, I only heard a little bit. That's all I heard. What was it again?
I don't remember. Just so we're all clear, what was the joke that was made on this show?
The joke was what I just told you. The pilot is thinking to himself, "Am I going to do Letterman or should I do Leno?" You know, this is what you say. And comparing it to Sully, there is a lot of Sully stuff going on.
Yes.
Yeah.
So.
Could you just frunkus us and get this over with? Ronnie?
Yes?
Could you just frunkus us and get this over with?
He's not a frunkus guy.
What is a frunkus? I don't even know what it is.
What was happening in the Boomer show that was so outrageous? I mean, it must have been crazy if it got you to turn the station.
What's that Craig guy up to these days?
Craig Carton actually has to do a speak to get me,
Wow, you're an easily bothered guy, Ronnie.
Boomer broke my arm, so how about that? I'm offended.
No. Well, guys, all I want to say is, look, I thought it was unbelievably insensitive.
Of course you did.
And but you don't think that it was in the slightest bit insensitive?
No!
You should listen to our show. You should hear what we talk about when we talk about people starving in foreign countries and people being blown up and beheaded and things like that.
Well, guys, I think I'm going to take a pass on the invitation, but thanks for taking my call.
Anyway. We'll go back to the outrageous sports show. When that offends you, come back to the show and act like you didn't know what the show was. But you still have the phone now.
Ronnie, let me ask you something before you leave. Is it okay to make fun of the Titanic?
Yes. Well, I'll put it to you this way. I wouldn't be as outrageously offended as I was today. Because
you know, over 1,000 people died on that.
Yeah, yeah, children died,
but
frozen
to
death.
Time kills all, it's time, you know, heals all wounds.
All right, so how long, Ronnie, how long can we wait?
How long
can we wait?
A couple years maybe on this one?
Make fun of things.
Wait until the bodies are cold, at least, boys. How's that sound?
Okay, so that's your thing.
Hey, it was Buffalo. They were very cold.
Oof.
There you go.
Wow.
There you go. Well, hey, what more can I say? You know, I mean, if you're going to make a statement like that again,
But Ronnie, do you hear what you're saying? Like, this is what drives people crazy with humor. This is like when a guy like you will call, and this is why I said it was self-righteous indignation, because then he points out something right, like the Titanic.
Right.
And it's like, you're like, well, it was a long time ago. I didn't feel anything. So because you personally, or any of us, of course, don't remember it or didn't know anybody, it's okay. Do you understand that stupid little, that little invisible line you're painting? People who are truly funny normally don't paint that line. And that to me is what's bothering me about what you're saying.
That's not really an invisible line, guys. That's human nature. I mean, if something happened in the second century, obviously I am not going to be as personally as something that is happening in front of my eyes.
Human nature.
You're watching on the TV.
Hold on, Ronnie. Human nature, kind of like gallows humor, kind of like when things happen that are tragically, people throughout their lives learn to respond to dealing with horrible things through humor. So that's kind of human nature too, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Okay, well then why is your version of human nature more valid and ours offensive?
Yours was offensive today. Yours was absolutely offensive.
Offended
you, Ronnie. But then again, Craig Carton offends you. So there's two things on the radio that you're listening to that bother you.
Why are you not listening?
Let me ask you something. Does Craig Carton offend you?
I honestly don't know what Craig Carton does. I know who he is, but I've never... Would he offend me? No.
He probably would.
I like his brother, Milk.
Ronnie, I'm so difficult to offend. I'm not offended.
Who are you, anyway?
Does it matter who I am? I'm not offended.
No, I was just curious. I don't even know your name.
My name is Jim. Doesn't matter.
Yeah.
I'm not offended by what other people say when expressing themselves politically or in humor, even if I don't like it. Paul Mooney's a comic, a pretty radical black comic, says a lot of things that I completely disagree with, but I've never been offended by humor in my life, ever.
Well, the difference is here, I didn't find what you said to be humorous.
You didn't, right?
But you knew the tone in which it was said. Otherwise, you wouldn't have called and said, "Why are you making it? Making fun of it?" You knew the intent was humor, so don't back out.
No, that's a really weak intent. I thought it was mean spirited, not humorous. I found nothing humorous about it. I didn't even find it as a. If I really think about it, I guess it was a very feeble attempt at humor.
Okay, you didn't like the joke, but you did know it was a joke. Don't lie. Just be honest.
No. Did I know it was a joke? Not particularly, no. And I don't think...
You thought we were doing a news report then?
You didn't even think it was a real plane crash. So you obviously thought it was something. So you thought you were hearing plane crash news and you just turned it off?
I didn't know it was a real plane crash.
Then why would we be talking about it if it wasn't done in humor?
We started off by saying it was a real story.
No, I wasn't outraged. You didn't listen to it. When I first heard it, I wasn't outraged. I didn't know what you were talking about. When I went to the other station and realized that it was indeed a real plane crash, then I became outraged.
The fact that you became outraged is embarrassing.
Embarrassing to whom?
For you! Yeah. The fact that you'd be outraged, you're annoyed at Craig Carton, he bothers you. I'm outraged at that humor. You're just one of those guys that wants to be heard.
You're outraged too much.
Yeah, stop being so outraged. It's boring.
I'm outraged that you're outraged.
He annoys me.
All right.
He annoys you. You're outraged. What else bothers you, Ronnie?
What else
on TV or in the media is offensive to your violates your set of what should be made fun of or spoken about or expressed?
Let me ask you something. What outrages you?
Oh.
Honestly?
You.
People like yourself who find what other people say to be bothersome and feel the need to call and snivel about it. Honestly, I've never had that urge. I'm 40 years old, dude. I've never had that urge.
Now, I didn't catch what you said. People call and be what about it?
And snivel about it.
Oh, snivel?
Yeah.
I see.
You called the radio station and went on the air to go, I didn't like what you made fun of. And it's never occurred to me to do that.
Right, so I don't have the right to call you.
Sure you do. Ronnie, whoa, I didn't question your
right. I took your call. Ronnie.
No, no one's questioning
Ronnie,
your right.
What do you find funny?
Yeah, what is your humor?
You obviously don't like our humor. So what do you find funny, Ronnie? So
I don't say I don't like your humor. I didn't like, I've never heard of you guys.
Yeah, I understand. Regardless.
What? So I may find you guys hysterical.
But okay, all right, we get it, Ronnie. But what do you find funny?
I find a lot of things funny.
Like what? Give us an example.
What do you like find funny?
No, you know, because we attempted humor today. What do you find funny? Seriously.
Just say something.
A movie?
Okay, I find Jay Leno funny. How's that sound?
What's that?
I find Jay Leno funny.
Very funny guy.
You ever, hear him do rape jokes?
Not that I recall. Not that I recall.
What was the funniest movie you ever saw?
Funniest movie? Animal House.
All right. So far, you know, we're kind of on the same page.
Underage sex.
Yeah. Was,
drinking.
Yeah. Date rape. There's a nice date rape scene in there. That was pretty funny, right?
That's a good one.
With an underage girl, actually.
Guys, you're not talking to the most prudish guy in the world right
now.
I'm not. I found this particularly offensive because of the subject matter at the time.
Understandable, but we're pointing out that when people are offended at humor, their offense is so inconsistent, and that's why I never take it seriously. Because the little morality thing that flag that people wave when it comes to something that just happens to bother them is completely inconsistent. And
I'm not going to wave a flag about something that bothers someone else. I'm not concerned about what bothers someone else. I can't be.
Thank you. Thank you, Ronnie.
Right. I could only be outraged at what me.
So why should we in any way, shape, or form be concerned about what bothers somebody else? We have the same human nature you do. We care about us. Just you care about you and your sensibilities, and everybody else on the planet is the same.
And do you understand that you are one...
Either.
Hey, hold on. Do you understand that you are one person that is offended by something? And every word that comes out of our mouth, somebody will find it offensive. So if we just stopped doing what everyone found offensive, we wouldn't be able to even open our mouths.
That might be a good idea, actually. But
snap!
So what are you going to say that?
Oh,
so why?
Yes.
Because everybody else. How about with some things you say offend people and you don't open your mouth?
Yeah, right.
Well, you know, here's the thing. I mean, you don't have to be concerned with what outrages me. I'm simply calling you and saying, this is what I felt, okay?
But you needed to be heard, didn't you, Ryan?
And you gave me a forum to do it.
You needed to be heard. Why did you need to be heard on it? That's what I don't get.
I didn't need to be heard. I didn't need to be heard.
So you called the radio station to talk about what bothered you, instead of just going, nah, that's not for me, and moving on. Like,
let me put it this way, guys. This is the first time I've ever called the radio station in my life. God, you know.
Congrats.
I believe you.
Quack, quack.
And I didn't have to be on the radio to do this. I simply...
You wanted to call and complain to the management.
I wanted to... No, I said I wanted to speak to you guys, and you were nice enough to put me through. But I could have... All you could have done was answer said, you know what, I'll call you back when the show is over. That would have been
Why
fine.
Would we what? Call you? What are you, nuts?
Oh, my God.
Who are you?
On a Friday?
We'll call you back when the show's over,
I'm
guy?
I'm dodging savages on the road. I'm going to be calling you.
I didn't need the forum of a live radio show.
But you needed to connect with the people who said it and tell them that it bothered you. You needed to be heard.
I did.
But it's silly. I don't get it.
Guys, your entire livelihood is needing to be heard.
Yes, it's my job. Exactly.
What do you do?
You know, so you decided to go into this profession because of your unbelievable desire to be heard.
Yes,
that's the first time I've ever done in my life. You're going to knock me for needing to be heard when you can't even exist without being heard.
Because you need to be heard because you want to tell people that your feelings were hurt or that you were bothered by something or you need to scold somebody. It's silly. You're not making a living off it. You're not entertaining people doing it. It's for your own satisfaction.
Neither are you. What do you do? What do you do?
The truth.
What do you do, Ronnie?
I work in the financial services.
There you go.
Another scumbag.
Yeah.
Great.
Hey.
You're one of these asses that we got to bail out.
Scumbag Wall Street guy. This is what you just called me.
Is that it?
Is that what you are, Wall Street guy, Ronnie?
Good.
Yeah, that's right.
Really? Did you call Bernie Madoff's house?
Your morality is...
What do I have to do with...
Your morality's down the crapper a lot more than ours, you hypocritical son of a bitch. Why don't you jump out a window?
Son of a bitch.
Choke your wife and jump out a window.
The way...
Choke your wife and jump out the window.
The way...
Who are you yelling to, Ronnie?
I sit in a trading floor here about
The way the vultures on Wall Street have behaved in this country, and you're offended at what people are saying in humor?
Be offended by the people that are surrounding you.
Don't paint everyone with the same brush.
Oh, don't paint everyone with the same brush.
Right, you're different. You're
different. Oh, look at you.
You guys aren't serious about this, right?
Completely serious. What I said about Bernie Madoff.
In your opinion, everybody who works on Wall Street is what you just called them.
I know. The image is a little tarnished. Let's just say that.
We're offended by our financial statements there, Ronnie.
Yeah.
So am I.
That's a lot. That's a lot bigger problem than silly radio shows.
I'm appalled by my financial statement. I saw a lot of people.
Oh, I'm sure.
You're probably one of the guys who, in some way, contributed to the problem.
Sure. I'm sure you saw something coming. No, Ronnie.
Yeah, I did.
So, did you get all your people out?
No. You see, no, I'm not. And I don't do equities, gentlemen. I do something completely different. I do bonds, but that's neither here nor there. But yeah, I mean.
Oh.
Wow, we offended a stock. We offended a stockbroker. Our apologies.
I'm not a stockbroker. I just told you.
I don't know the difference, dude. What hair? You're a Wall Street guy. I could care less.
All Wall Street guys are bad guys. It's just like all radio guys are bad.
Not,
guys.
No. I didn't say bad guys. Irrelevant to me. I don't care what you think or feel. It means nothing to me.
Right. Okay. So you dismiss an entire portion of the population.
What do you think about tax-free munis in New York right now?
Mm-hmm.
Should we buy? I have no comment on it, gentlemen.
Why?
Come on.
Why? Where are we at with GM?
Helping N-word out.
Is it a good buy or what?
Because I can't comment on it.
Why can't you comment on it?
What do you
Literally,
think?
I can't comment on it.
Who's buying Sirius XM and should we be buying these shares? Come on. Let's get some done here.
No idea.
Let's get some done here, Ronnie.
I do, boys.
That GM looks really inviting. Should we go in or what?
I wouldn't have the slightest clue. If you looked at my portfolio, you'd understand. Don't do what I do.
What about bonds? What about T-bills?
Yeah. Where are we at with T-bills and gold?
Again, some T-bills?
That I can't comment on.
What
are we doing today?
What do you do?
Comment on us.
Yeah, we're talking about us for a half hour, but you can't comment on something that's helpful?
Should we?
No, legally I can't do it.
Do you work on the CIA? You could talk about it.
Should we puts? No. Should we puts today or what?
You guys should definitely puts. I'll put it that way.
Oh, wait. Because we're a bunch of... thank you, Ronnie.
I
don't know what we got done here, but, I mean, I saved you from the wrath of the fans, trust me.
I hope you'll lose your whole retirement.
Why do you have to say something?
Well, because that's true. Because that's your livelihood, and you're going after ours.
Oh, man. You know, guys.
All right, Ronnie, we're going to be friends, I can tell.
Now,
you'll be listening to the show. We intrigued you today.
Now,
I think we got a new listener.
You did.
We got a new listener.
I have to be honest. We got a new listener.
It's going
to
really bother you when you really start liking the show, and you're like, oh, my God, that was the show I hated.
Call us back.
What's wrong with me?
Call us back when you kind of start changing over and go, all right, guys.
I'll be in touch, boys, all right?
All right, beat it, stupid.
I do appreciate
it. All right, beat it, stupid.
All right, Ronnie. Ronnie's a douche.
All right, it's Opie and Anthony. Let's see what everyone else is bitching about today. Here's the FU line.
Thanks for calling the Opie and Anthony FU line. Here's the latest batch of FUs.
You have 7 new voice messages. First voice message.
Yeah, I'd like to give a big FU to the New York Islanders and Rick DPS show. Thanks to you guys, I haven't been able to watch an effing goddamn game in 3 years. F you, Islanders.
Next message.
I want to give a big fuck you to myself because despite doing nothing wrong, I woke up this morning to my girlfriend telling me, screw you, and I ended up apologizing to her. What a fucking pussy am I. Fuck you, myself.
Next message.
Hey, you fucking disgusting monster in the lane next to me. Why don't you put your goddamn phone down and concentrate on your fucking horrid ability to drive? You fucking disgusting...
Next message.
Yeah, I would like to send a nice big F you to my supposed girlfriend, who I try nothing but to please her and break my back and practically go broke to pick a fight with me during the week of Valentine's Day and even give her a bigger surprise that I'm not going to give her because she decided to fight with me. How queen.
Next message.
Hi, I just want to give a big F you to my boss, who I asked for a raise and now he totally ignores me. Fuck you.
Next message.
Hi, I want to give
big F you to Peter, Lisa, Michael, and all the other assholes where I work. Thanks for letting me know that I was getting a pay cut by putting it in the fucking paper. You guys are a bunch of pussies. Fuck you. Next message.
Yeah, this is Drunk Chris from Long Island. I'd like to give a big F you to All Brains, a single malt scotch, for going down so smooth and starting the night off great, only to later convince me it was a good idea to slap my date and yell out dumb shit at Jimmy's 10:30 show Friday at Caroline's, and leaving me with chills with the Duke variety for the foreseeable future. I'm glad I slapped a bitch and all, but I should know better than to leave comedy to the professionals. Fuck you!
End of you, messages.
Call the Opie and Anthony FU line, 866-FU-LINE-1. That's 866-FU-LINE-1.
Thank you, and goodbye.
Valentine's Day is tomorrow. I want to acknowledge all the people that hate Valentine's Day, by the way. I know you're out there.
All right. I have to mention something that's going on tonight.
What's that?
This is the 2U 3D. You won't believe this.
Joe rules.
Brother Joe.
He rules.
Has been in his basement like a mad scientist.
Right.
Putting this together. And it really is unbelievable. It's a multimedia retrospective introspective that spans U2's career via live concerts by 2U, of course, the world's second best U2 show, performing simultaneously with synchronized original U2 video on a giant screen. So to a T, they are playing on stage. And to a T, it matches up with the video of U2 that's behind him on a giant screen.
How the F is he doing that?
Amazing. Joe's like a rocket scientist when he wants to be. This is at the Dix Hills Performing Arts Center in Five Towns College. It's tonight, February 13th, starts at 7 p.m. Tickets are $20. They're available at dhpac.org. dhpac.org. Or you can call the box office 631-656-2148. And it's really going to look unbelievable.
I'm a huge U2 fan. I might have to drive my new whip out to Dix Hills tonight.
The whip out there to Five Towns College, Dix Hills Performing Arts Center, 2U3D, he's calling it.
That's pretty cool,
it's
man.
It's a whole thing. Yeah, giant screen, U2 playing, and the band is exactly in sync with the videos that are going on behind him. So it's very cool.
I'm a tough critic, and I got to tell you, Brother Joe's U2 band.
Yeah.
I went and saw U2 at the Garden, and then he was at, where was it, House of Blues, I think?
Yep.
Doing an after U2 party, and I went there to hear a lot of the songs that the real band didn't do at the Garden.
They didn't play.
And sounded just like the band.
Yeah.
It was awesome.
Yeah, so check that out.
I'm not sure if I like the new U2 song yet.
No.
I'm not really sure if I like it.
There's some
something
some
about
U2
boots.
Songs got to like kind of grow on me. There's a couple that hit me right away.
Yeah. You know, Vertigo?
Yeah, Vertigo was one that like
yeah,
right
I
away
like
I liked
one.
That.
Yeah.
I like that right
Beautiful
away.
Beautiful Day gets right into your soul.
I don't
some
know
of
that
them
one.
Got to grow on you, but
City of Blinding Lights from the last album was amazing.
And if you're into U2,
I'm a big U2.
They just don't really reach me. I don't know why. I don't think they suck. They just never reach me. Yeah.
I like them. Joshua Tree is still one of my favorite CDs of all time.
What's a big song off that?
Everything. Where the Streets Have No Name. With or Without You. I like a little song called Red Hill Mining Town.
Where's what?
Too obscure to play here today.
The Streets Have No Name. How's that go? Because I've heard With or Without.
The Streets Have No Name.
That doesn't sound like a fun town. Yeah. I want the streets have names.
Very hard to navigate.
Oh.
Turn down that street and then that street.
Dude.
Make a left on the other street and you'll be there.
When I was wandering America when we were off the air, I found myself in Phoenix, Arizona, and I decided, I'm going to drive to L.A. because I have no one to report to. I have nothing to do. And I'm on the highway from Phoenix to L.A., and all of a sudden I see Joshua Tree National Park.
Yeah,
I'm like, this is perfect. U2 fan, nothing to do, no one to report to.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go see the trees, man.
Yes.
That made the Joshua Tree album so famous.
And what did you say?
Holy ass. Man, did they trick me and got me off that highway.
Oh, man, I know.
You know this?
Oh, I've been to Joshua Tree.
Oh, so you know.
Oh, yeah.
I had to finally give up.
no joke, 20 to 30 miles in, and it wasn't 20 or 30 miles of highway in. It's
no.
It's like a two-lane road that's windy and curvy, and you
and
really
after
can't.
A while, they turn into dirt roads.
Right.
Once you get into, like, well, this is years ago anyway, once you get into Joshua Tree,
right.
A little town called Joshua Tree, and you get in there, and the houses are there, but the streets, are, and maybe that's where the streets have no name, because they're just dirt roads.
Right.
That are on kind of a grid, and these houses are there, and there's these, you know, Joshua trees that just look like nuclear wreckage trees.
I was so bummed because I finally had to give up. I'm like, I'm not going to get to see the Joshua trees, you know? Because I think it said something like another 50 or 60 miles, and the 20 miles took, when I tell you the 20 miles took well over an hour, I'm like, I'm going to do this for another 50 or 60? No effing way.
When you're
so
driving,
I turned it around.
When you're driving in the desert, everything is forever away.
Yeah.
It just really is.
But it looks right there.
Forever. It looks like it's right there. I swear to you. When we used to do that camping thing out in the Mojave Desert, it would take forever to get there.
Mm-hmm.
And you'd be in the middle of nowhere and have to turn off and do another 50 miles from nowhere.
Yeah.
From like the last
nowhere
piece
point.
Of crap gas station.
Sure. But I loved it, though. Amazing. I loved that there was nothing. You know, I should have done this stuff when I was younger. I got the opportunity when we got fired. I did the ride from L.A. to Vegas for the first time. That ride ruled.
Dude, there's a feeling out there in the middle of the desert.
It's awesome.
That, like,
you can't even explain it.
And I'm not talking about on the road or anything. Off the beaten path. When you step out of the vehicle, shut it off, and just stand there and listen and smell and just look around, it is the eeriest. It's like almost spiritual. I swear to you. It's almost, for me, who is the most unspiritual person. It really, you're kind of standing there just like hearing every little, like, breeze blowing across the little grass that's poking up out of the sand. And it's just a fantastic place to just hang out.
I got something for you. Why, when you're in that situation that you just explained, why is the sky higher?
It does look.
You know what I'm talking about, though, right?
High out there.
Why does it look so much higher? The cloud, everything just looks higher.
Yeah.
What is that?
I guess it's because they don't have that layer of goop that the cities pump out to make it look lower.
It's so bizarre to me, though.
Yeah, it's a deep blue. And then at night, unless you've been there, you cannot even understand what the stars look like when there's no glare from a city.
Yeah.
There's no city within hundreds of miles of you. So, and you're in the middle of the desert. It's pitch blackness. And then the stars, you actually see white across the sky.
It almost looks white.
The stars are
so
close together that it just looks like a white streak of, you know, our galaxy.
Yeah,
the Milky Way.
When we're not picked up by the new company over there that's on satellite, then I'm going to go see the Joshua trees.
You're going to do that?
Finally.
See those Joshua trees.
I'm going.
I'm finally going to see them Joshua trees.
I'm going to send out a Twitter alert. Hey, meet me at the Joshua trees. I'm leaving today. I'll see you there.
What are they? They're just a bunch of trees. Why would they sing about them?
They're so weird looking, dude.
They're just bizarre. Trees. I don't know the history of them. I don't care. I just know they were on the album cover. I'm like, all right, I'm going there.
I said, it's the whole thing of just being out in nowhere.
Yeah, I loved it. Dude, I loved it.
Driving
to Vegas, I was out of my mind because I never saw anything like that in my entire life.
I was dressed like the Khmer Rouge, but
nice.
I really,
Paul in Jersey, I hate you too. This offends me. Oh, no. Oh, boy.
He's offended.
Oh, boy.
Oh, Uncle Paul. I heard that chuckle.
Mark, today I got something in common with Stephen S. from Bayshore. He loves Red Hill Mining Town, too. Too obscure, Jimmy. Can't go there.
I don't know how any of them go.
Go there. I still haven't found what I'm looking for. But the gospel singers, if you get the right version.
Haven't found what I'm looking for. I don't think it's great. I think it's okay.
The whole album. It's one of those rare albums that has...
Yeah, kind of like...
every song is good.
Like Sabotage.
Yeah. You don't know this song?
This, yeah.
Oh, you know
Which is called... this is okay. This I'm still having fun. I kind of like the... I've been waiting.
That's not my name. That's not my name.
You didn't really get into U2, huh?
No, I wasn't a big U2 fan until maybe a few years back. Kind of got turned onto it.
Right.
Yeah.
Rattle and Hum is a great album because they inject a lot of gospel into that.
You know what it was? They were too like political, and it annoyed me when like Bono, they were touring the U.S. once, and it's like, Bono has shunned the press, and he's going to let his music do the talking. And I was just like, oh, shut up, you pompous ass.
I have a way of like separating those two because Bono's like the trying to save the world thing. I'm like, whatever. I just like what you're doing with your music. I could separate. I really can.
Did you like the mulleted Bono
Dude.
Or the one now? The mulleted
well,
Bono.
Well, you...
The early days.
You were at the Garden for the famous
YouTube
thing
was
where
fantastic.
there wasn't a dry eye in the house. I have no problem admitting I bawled like a little girl, man.
No.
What was the song they played?
Was it
One?
One.
I think they played One, and then they showed everyone that was lost. Down there at Ground Zero.
9/11. They wanted to show the list of the names.
The list of the planes.
And it just
names.
Went forever
and
ever.
So the people in the building and the names.
It was like
firefighters.
It was like a credit roll.
It went on forever. It was just like, oh my God.
Dude, by the time song, I got chills thinking about it. By the time that song ended, people were looking at strangers just going, yeah, I'm with you, man. This is just a moment that I'll never forget.
Yeah. Could you pass me that dupe? Very.
As far as concert moments, that's probably my biggest highlight right there.
Yeah, that was a biggie.
Although the Leonard Skinner, and I certainly don't want to compare the two, because I know there's idiots out there ready to jump on anything we do.
Play some Skinner, man.
But when I saw Leonard Skinner at Darien Lake, when they got back together, they finally decided about after 10 years, and you know what? It sucks that we lost our... Oh, the mullet guy.
God damn, that
forget about
mullet.
That. That's from...
Bono.
That's from the Live Aid and all that, right?
Yeah.
The Leonard Skinner, though, after 10 years, they go, look, we lost our lead guy, but there's still fans out there that want our music. And you know, there's 20 guys in our band, so why don't we get his younger brother?
Yeah.
So the younger brother comes out, and he was awesome. Sounds like his older brother. But then the moment that they were going to play Freebird, I love telling the story.
Oh, yeah.
All of a sudden, what's the younger Van Zandt?
Is it Donnie? I know Ronnie was the singer.
There's Ronnie, there's Donnie, there's Johnny. I get them all confused, but you know who I'm talking about.
No, it's not Ted Van Zandt.
I'm as free as a bird now.
Birds are very free. We have that in common, Gregory.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, they did that at the Super Bowl, too, but at the Garden, it was even more impressive, the U2 thing. Anyway, so the van, whatever, Ronnie, Johnny, or Donnie, whatever. I think Donnie was in 38 Special, actually. he got the short end of the stick, definitely. All of a sudden, he's like, this next song, there's only one guy that should sing this song, and unfortunately, he's not here. So, this goes out to him.
And then he takes his hat, his older brother's hat, puts it on the mic stand. There's one stupid freaking light on the mic stand.
What?
Just thinking of the hat.
Take it away, Jimmy.
I actually don't have one. The hat on the mic stand.
I was just thinking it's kind of smoldering.
Oh, jeez. Still smoldering. They just kept it lit. The eternally... anyway, and then...
Paul did that. Paul did that for George Harrison. But then all you heard was glub, glub from the pudding in the microphone.
why tell a story, right?
Why F tell it. A story?
F it. Who cares?
Oh, my
Look God. Up the story online.
No, go ahead. I'm sorry.
I forgot. These guys don't have an emotional bone in their body. Stupid me. Stupid me. I forgot. I'm dealing with two guys that don't have a soul. And nothing like gets them chilling.
Oh, wait, are you saying Paul did that to George to put a plastic baggie over the mic first?
Why, yeah, first.
Why show an emotion? You're right. Go with the tumor jokes for another 10 minutes. I'm sorry. I was mistaken. I was mistaken.
We're putting it. That's terrible. Mm. All right.
Yeah, whatever.
They put a hat there on the mic stand. No one sang?
No.
They just did an instrumental version?
Yeah, and there wasn't a
did
dry...
Did the crowd sing?
Yeah.
Yeah,
there wasn't a dry eye in the house.
Yeah.
But now they do it to the point where now it's like, whatever,
it's hack now.
It's not even that special anymore.
I want someone to sing it.
Yeah. I think he finally started singing it, finally, I think.
Yeah.
If I know my Skinner.
Mm.
But and that's a long instrumental, but they were right there. They sang the whole effing song, and there was one light on the hat.
On the hat. The hat!
What about the hat?
But he got his hat! It's on the mic stand! His hat! Stupid Dyson, his hat.
He should have put a curly wig on the mic stand and sang the Brady Bunch theme song.
The stand still would have had to lose weight.
Okay, base two covered.
All we need is a good Modesto joke and we can go home.
And we'll have the final check.
Oh, God. Be terrible.
This guy just drove through Joshua Tree yesterday. Ooh. John in Utah. John, what did I miss?
Well, not a lot. I mean, they're kind of impressive as far as, like, looking at weird plants, but it is desolate. It's a lot of nothing out there. I mean, the only way we knew where we were delivering to was we had to have a GPS coordinate.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I think I didn't miss anything.
No, what? GPS in the old days when me and Foot and Bison took a Camaro cross country.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that. Drove through the desert. Lost an alternator. I'd get that fixed in some bum F town, and then
did they just rape you?
Oh yeah,
they just were like, "Oh, this is gonna be $2,000."
Oh hell yeah! And then we stop for gas before like that road that looks like the road that where Sarah Connor got gas and then drove off into the storm. That's exactly what
pretty
it
much
looked
the same
like.
Gas station.
Oh man, yeah,
really?
It was just here you go, last chance gas. Good luck to you.
Don't they have signs, too? If you don't fill up here,
you're done.
Will run out of
you're
gas.
Just, you're done.
We got this figured out here.
You're so conscious of your gas, too, at that point, where you're looking at your tank and going, okay, it's 25 miles to the next gas station. You'll see the sign, and you start looking at the gas gauge going, I got to make this? Because you know you can't just be like, hey, dude, you know, could you take me up to the gas station? Because there's no one on the road.
But that was 20 years ago. You got to think now you're never going to run out of gas if you're paying attention to your instruments.
Yeah.
But it's kind of creepy to think 20 years ago or whatever it was, that you still had a chance to actually not find a gas station.
Yeah. You'd have to lean over a little so the gas gauge, you'd look at it and it'd come out of the red because of your angle, the way you're looking at it. You put your head way against the driver door and go, all right. Yeah, they wouldn't have put a gas gauge in that could let me see that if I still have gas, if I'm leaned over out my window. They wouldn't allow that.
I don't know why my wife's with me.
Yeah, would you? Are you reading everyone's mind right now? What are you doing?
Including
that's
hers.
Magic.
She reminded me of the Cape Cod running out of gas story. I'm like, why is she with me? She's looking down at my now old car.
The picture.
And she goes, yeah, are we going to make it? I'm like, yes, we're going to make it.
Ah, we got it.
And I think it's, what, Route 6 out there in Cape
Cod?
Don't
be silly.
Run out of gas. Way short of the exit.
Came up a little short.
Way short. And then we take a ride from some pot-smoking kids in a van, all tatted up. And this is the van where they didn't have seats. And they go, we'll get you to a gas station.
Did you help them with a couch?
They throw us in the back of the van with these...
You took your wife in the back of a van?
Well, she was my girl. You know, I was still feeling it out, you know.
Yeah, no, I'm just kidding. Yeah, it wasn't like, you know, caring like now. But
yeah, now I got to really care for it. No, and I went in the back of this van, no seats. Everyone's hanging around just talking music and going to some tat show or seeing a band, I forget now. They're all smoking pot. And then the guy, to get in the back of the van, he takes out a key and undoes the padlock in the back of the van, and I still jumped in with my girl.
Are you out of your mind?
There
it is. That's the road.
Yeah. And then we sat in the van with all these kids as they're smoking pot, talking music, and then the guy takes off going about 100 miles on Route 6 somewhere on Cape Cod to get me to the exit.
How long?
I was out of my mind scared.
How long from the exit were you?
It was a while. It was easily a 10-15 minute ride. Easily. I was so short on this one. I really...
Wow, you
why
really
did you stop and get
up.
Gas before?
I had it figured out, I thought.
Yeah, huh?
And then I was like, oh, my God, the next exit's 10 miles. I'm like, oh, this isn't good. Oh, no. Oh, no. And I knew it, too. And I'm like, oh, please. Please, maybe there's a gas god.
Oh, boy.
But then I'm sitting on the floor of this horrible van, and then he locks us in.
Yeah.
Gets us in and then locks us, because that was the only way to keep the door shut.
That's
so if the thing crashed, we would have been after. We wouldn't have been able to pop out of that thing.
No. We used it to, like, bring people over the border or something.
Yeah, I don't know.
Oof.
They ended up cool. I lucked out that time.
You certainly did.
You know, I'm here. I own some, like, independent record store in Boston. I got a good story out of it. What the hell?
I was always petrified to do anything like take rides from people, hitchhike thing.
My
mother used to just, like, put the fear in me. Yeah, they're awful people. They're going to chop your head off. They're going to kill you.
I was a dope. I used to hitchhike from Geneseo to Buffalo to fly home. And I would take a steak knife and put it in my sock, and then I would just pop my thumb out and take a ride.
In case someone attacks you with a filet mignon.
But here's me thinking, I could fight off anybody with a steak knife.
Steak knife.
So I had it in my sock.
Yeah.
And I would then pop my thumb out, and then whoever picked me up, whatever.
Punch you, you'd fall.
Hope for the best.
Cut your Achilles tendon.
Right. And then I would always just throw the steak knife in the garbage as I was going into the airport. You know, security was way more lax back then.
Yeah.
You probably could have, like, carried that on the plane almost.
Yeah, just hand you my own knife for a meal.
All right. We'll mop up next, right?
Mop. Get the mop out.
Sky is higher because there's no hills. I don't know what it is.
What?
When you're out west
giant
in the desert
in the
stuff,
desert.
The sky just looks way higher.
Giant mountains in the desert. I climbed up one of those things once and just stood at the top. Could see for so far. It was ridiculous.
Did Mickey and Mallory sleep with you?
No, they didn't sleep with me. Either.
Mickey and Mallory, nice, yes.
I really like the desert, the Mojave Desert. I mean, it's a great place to just be, just to hang out there. Of course, you know, shooting everything that moves is a lot of fun, too.
Yeah, I liked it out there, too.
It's just so weird. It's an alien world. It's like no other. Even a small town is a town. It's a community. There's people there. You are just alone out there. Whoever you're with, that's it.
Can I tell you the greatest place I've ever been?
Greatest place you've ever been. I'm going to say
in America. In America.
For me.
Let me guess.
In America.
Trenton.
Trenton's up there, Jimmy. Right the F up there. There's a tough decision between Sedona. Sedona, Arizona is the most amazing place I've ever been.
You sure it's not Sedona?
Sedona. S-E-D-O-N-A. With the red rocks and stuff, it is ridiculous.
Yeah.
Mountain biking with my brother in Sedona was one of the greatest.
That's where the harmonic convergence.
That was
one of the points.
And you know what? That was
And
that was before the Grand Canyon. We stopped in Sedona.
Before the Grand Canyon, that's been there forever. Stop it.
And I think Sedona in many ways was much cooler than the Grand Canyon.
Yeah? Yeah.
Yeah. It was amazing.
Grand Canyon.
Effing amazing, man. All right.
I like the episode of the Brady Bunch where they went to the Grand Canyon.
Yes.
My father looked into it and said, "That's nothing."
Because all the donkeys were going down. It's like, oh God, that's as many mules. Yeah. Had more than that.
Bunch of mules going into that big hole.
Yeah. He kept yelling, "Lucky Grand Canyon."
Why the Mojave Desert end?
Because of the like I said, it's if I was a spiritual person, it's almost spiritual. It's just it's everything. There's a sound and a smell out there that I'll never forget.
Is it all even sand though, or is it?
No. It's mountains and brush and sand and it's not a desert like the Sahara Desert, like people just picture sand dunes. It's there's mountains and valleys and we went exploring through these canyons. Where there's just giant boulders that you know were in that same place when, like, dinosaurs were walking next to them, you know, and just hadn't been moved. It's just the oldness of it is amazing. Because we were in a place where there was nobody, and it wasn't a well-traveled area. This was the middle of the Mojave Desert in about, you know, the mid-70s.
Right.
So it was just nothingness. It was very cool.
When did you realize your life means nothing?
It was kind of
as
around
far
that time.
As far as the time thing goes.
You see a vastness that is so much bigger than you.
Like the Grand Canyon, like, oh my God.
And you realize what a little blip you are on the radar screen.
My moment was, I was in the hole. I think it's H-O, maybe, I think H-O, rainforest.
Oh, okay. And joking.
Right. I think it's called the Ho Rainforest. This is many years ago. With good old John O'Brien. Remember him from AM?
Yes.
I went out to Seattle to visit him. And we went into the rainforest. and I saw a tree that was probably something like 400 years old on the ground in the rainforest.
Yeah.
Massive, like almost as wide as this room. What am I looking at? Like 15 feet across, easy? Just down in the forest, right? And there was a tree growing out of this that started as a little nothing that was easily 8 feet around.
So a tree was growing out of a tree.
Yeah, and the tree that fell had a life of easily, whatever, 300-400 years. Yeah. And now the new tree was easily into 200 years. I'm like, wow, okay, I get it. I get it.
We really got the crappy end of the stick as far as longevity goes on this planet.
Right.
Yeah, but we didn't have to just wait. We want 600 years of just standing there while birds take dumps on you. I'd rather have 70 person years running around having sex. What are you gonna do? Drop acorns again. The sounds here. No one knows if anyone hears it because I don't have ears. They bark. Bees live on me.
Thank God Jimmy brings it right back. Thank you, Jimmy.
It certainly does.
Thank you for the laugh.
You can't even grope the thing next to you?
No.
You gotta hope some squirrel carries stuff?
A little sucks. The wind pushes you over.
But yeah, it was like some kind of acorn fell onto this tree that was rotting in the forest and grabbed hold, and then it's living its life through this tree that fell in the freaking forest.
Danny found a good picture there.
That's Mojave?
Yeah, it looks like part of it.
Why don't you go back out there?
A lot of brush. Yeah, what am I going to do now? When I was a kid, it was fun. We had dune buggies and guns and
you still got things guns, like that. And you still got kids.
Now they probably surveillance. It wouldn't be anything like I remembered it. I just like remember. We drove through these towns like that were just, they were big towns until the freeway went through, like Baghdad. There was a place called Baghdad.
For real?
Out there, yeah. And Amboy was another place, and these were just like foundations, and then you'd get out and see these little things like a coffee can from like the early 1900s and stuff.
Love that stuff.
When it was an old mining town. And
is it pretty much like, quote, a ghost town? There's nothing happening
totally.
Anymore?
Exactly.
God, I would love to check that out.
And it's just the coolest thing, because all you hear is this constant, like just wind kind of blowing through. And it's very cool.
I would have no problem spending like days there. I would just camp there. I don't care.
We were in the Old Woman Mountains, they were called. The Old Woman Mountains, an old silver mine.
Yeah.
And we stayed in the mining shack and drank tequila I was 13 years old.
Did Dad have a gun with him? You guys had guns.
We all were armed to the teeth with every kind of pistol and rifle and machine guns at that point. I mean, they had everything.
Yeah, you seem like you want to be armed out there.
Yeah, yeah. Any stranger, because you'd never bump into anybody unless they meant you no good. There's no reason to be out there.
Yeah, I think if you bump into someone else, that could be a problem.
Yeah, he's trying to stink my claim.
Right. You know some lunatic that has decided he's the mayor of Ghost Town.
Yeah. Exactly.
Comes out of the woodworks.
Take a break. He's stunt. He's going nuts.
You know when I had that moment of nothingness where I realized my life was worthless?
Boss show?
No.
Oh.
When I woke up, yes. No, I was in bed with a gal.
Oh.
And I was hearing the, hey, look, don't be upset. It happens to everybody. And I realized I am of no value as a man.
You're nothing.
I am nothing.
All right, Opie and Anthony. We'll wrap up next. It's been fun just talking. Just kind of hanging and talking with my pals.
That's what I like doing.
My radio pals.
I like yapping about things.
We're all radio pals.
I got a text from our friend Roland.
Yeah, what did Roland have to say?
Three stories equal gay. Z. Let me tell you about A-Rod and the steroids. Hey-o!
Hey-o!
Then I wrote back, like, ha-ha, you're right. And he said, tell me about your garden is next. So Roland has given us a beating.
Roland's a smartass.
He really is. We let him too close to us. That was our mistake.
I don't know, now we're going to miss him.
Yeah, we do miss Roland. We'll get him back.
Yes.
Fun fact, Grand Canyon gets a quarter. I'll let this guy say it. Adam in Boston, how are you, Adam?
Hey, guys, what's going on? Fun fact Friday, I'm trying to bring it back. 10,000 years, Grand Canyon gets a quarter deeper and a dime wider. That's about it.
Wait, every 10,000 years it gets a quarter deeper and a dime wider?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, like the width of a quarter deeper and the width of a time wider.
I got it. So even if it was the length, does it matter?
Oh, my God.
Wait.
Exactly.
But that wind is blowing a lot of stuff around. It's not knocking.
If I went to the rim of the Grand Canyon and took my heel and kicked off a part that's five dimes wide, I just made it wider than that.
Yes. Where's that just makes us pathetic. Like, our lives are useless for a flash in the pan. Like, that just puts it in perspective.
I think your fact is wrong because I've heard that it actually equals 85 cents. You're doing a quarter of a dime, which is 35 cents. I totally disagree.
It all depends on what the dollar's worth at the time.
So. Yes, yeah. Your economics are off.
Yeah.
This is a hike you could do at the Grand Canyon, and you end up in a part of the Grand Canyon, and you start imagining this is how it has to be on a planet.
Yeah.
Another planet.
Yes.
It is so foreign to what you're used to.
Faraway land.
There was not a hint of growth. It was just rocks.
Rocks, different colored rocks. And
it was bizarre, man.
Yeah, love it out there.
Thank you, Adam.
Thanks, guys.
Let's say hi to Marine Joe in New York. Marine Joe, how are you?
Good evening.
Hello, Marine Joe.
Listen, I was stationed out in 29 Palms in the early 90s, and we did a lot of training out in the Mojave, but that Amboy area is where Charles Manson and all his lunatic followers were living, when that whole Helter Skelter thing happened, man. So it's a good thing you boys were running around armed.
Yeah, I know. That's what, when little Charlie Reyes got shot in our group and the police showed up, I'm sure they were thinking that, we must have been some kind of lunatics just hanging out there. But yeah, that Amboy area is it's pretty odd.
Absolutely. Hey, one thing for E-Rock before I punch out.
Yeah.
Hey, E-Rock.
Oh, well.
I hope you catch diabetes.
Oh, wow.
Jeez. Marine Joe. Yeah, let's go to Brendan in San Diego. Brendan.
Hey, boys. Hey.
Welcome aboard.
What's up, Brendan?
Well, a little small desert down by my town, Anthony would love it. My uncle's neighbor loves to fill trash bags up with saline and stick them in abandoned cars by them.
Clam?
Yeah, you have a lot of fun out in the desert there.
All right. Sounds great.
Well, thank you, Brendan. We got a quickie. Valentine's Day tomorrow. They're offering this somewhere out there.
Are you looking for the perfect Valentine's Day activity? A Michigan zoo is hosting an exotic afternoon for couples on Valentine's Day. No. The program is called Zoo-rotica. It gives adults an unabashed look at the mating habits of wild animals. The event is so popular, the zoo had to start a waiting list. For $50 per couple, visitors will receive champagne, snacks, and a guided tour of areas typically off limits to the public.
What if the animals don't feel like effing while you're there?
What pressure.
No kidding. How are they getting the animals to F?
They must keep them apart for a while and get them all horned up for this day.
That's hilarious.
Put them together and just...
You nailed it. Got to hear the groaning of animals. Oh, it's nothing worse.
That's what you want on Valentine's Day. To get a llama shooting on your foot. That's attractive.
Who needs that?
Crush your ankle.
Animals having sex on Valentine's Day.
What animal would you like to have sex with? Hello. What animal?
Probably a pig. Wow. They're smart. I appreciate it.
What animal would you like
to see have sex?
Really? No. Let me think.
It has to be something silly.
Porcupines.
Porcupines?
Oh, I gotta see how they navigate that.
Right?
It would be silly.
Yeah.
What about giraffes? That would be kind of silly.
Yeah, that's kind of silly to watch.
Can we mix Big species? Mix.
Yeah, you can mix a little species.
Mix them.
A horse and a turtle. But I want the turtle to be the giver.
Oh, wow.
Look at Danny.
Oh, that's porcupine.
Is that porcupine?
Danny finds it in a second. Two porcupines going at it.
That looks kind of silly, man.
That does look silly. Boy, that guy is really playing it safe.
I'm trying to think silly here. I mean, the lions... That'd be pretty impressive.
Show me Rhesus monkeys.
Really?
I bet they put stupid faces on.
Let me say hi to Suzanne in Philly. Suzanne.
Rhesus monkeys.
Suzanne.
Hi.
Hi, Suzanne. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Hi.
Good.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Okay. Hi. Thank you very much. Godspeed.
I was just going with the Fun Fact Friday thing again.
Okay.
The concrete at the Hoover Dam won't be dry for 500 years.
That's impossible.
Come on. The water's against it.
Mm. Inside of it.
Yes, inside. You know, concrete heats up very hot.
Yeah.
When it's curing.
So is it watery inside that?
What they had to do is actually run tubes through it and then feed water through the tubes to keep it cool because it cracks if it gets too hot. It's not as strong as it is. So yeah, they keep cooling it off, but it's still warm. The concrete is still hot from the chemical reaction of it drying inside. What? As we speak.
How do they figure that
Isn't
out?
Isn't that amazing?
Pretty neat.
Yeah.
That's a good fun fact.
That is a fun fact.
Having a lot of
fun. Oh, look at the rhesus monkeys going you. At it. Look at the woman one is looking up and going, tee-hee. The old fish eye. How can a monkey give a fish eye?
She's going, that's all you got.
Yeah, that it?
No, she's going lower. Wrong one.
He's a great Greek monkey.
They both have red faces. They're all embarrassed that the camera caught them being playful.
Look at him, though. He's like climbed up on her legs.
Oh, yeah, he's... She's looking at him going, listen, you sick F, it's not your birthday.
No. That's what are you doing? That is so funny.
Can I Twitter this? I don't think I can.
Why? It's just animals having sex. There's no human involved.
I don't know.
God, would I love to Photoshop that?
Of course you would. Did you have to even vocalize that?
I just want to Photoshop.
Wow, look at what's really weird.
You can do with it.
She's kind of on all fours, but she's braced. How strong is the female? She's bracing herself with her right arm. He is kind of behind her, but he's not standing on the ground. He's actually got his feet bracing on her calf.
Yeah.
And she's reaching back with her left arm, holding his left leg steady. So she's balancing both of their weight on her back legs and right arm.
And she just knows he likes a little jiggling. And she's reaching, giving the old reach around. Or maybe the monkey's like Jimmy, and she's trying for a digit.
No. You can actually hear, if you listen closely, the monkey's going, hee-lee-lee-lee-lee, with her two fingers.
You know what's great about that picture? She's looking at him like, you know, give me a little look of love. And he's looking straight ahead like, he's just getting the job done.
He's got that, face.
And all she wants is just a little... hint of some kind of caring.
Oh, you know, if that wasn't taken with a high-speed camera, that that monkey ass would be blurry as a paint shaker.
Right now, she's looking at him in a monkey talk going, where are you?
Yeah. Where are you emotionally?
We're not connecting anymore.
We should be more than just this. Should we? All right. Pick some nits out of my hair.
He's trying to look away from her. He's pretending she's a gorilla or anything other than what she is. She's a red-faced rhesus monkey.
Look at her red face.
Really? Figure out the sunscreen, stupid.
I think that's what it is. A little rhesus sunburn. You monkeys.
All right. We got to go.
Yes.
We got to go. Stump Brain, why don't you do something nice for the listeners as we leave you.
Stunte.
Yeah, we do have three more pair of tickets to the Rescue Me Comedy Tour, which is at Radio City.
Wouldn't it be three pairs?
What did he say?
Three
more pair.
I think a pair is plural, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. But
no, one pair.
We all just say three.
A pair is one unit of two.
Okay, we have six tickets, which can be broken down in pairs. And it's for the Radio City Show, April 2nd. Dennis Leary, Adam Ferrara, Lenny Clark, and of course they're going to show the season premiere of Rescue Me. They're on sale Monday morning at 10, but we do have three pairs to give away.
All right, and listen, make sure you can be in New York for the show on April 2nd at Radio City Music Hall, right?
Yes.
Okay. That's how we end today. Have a great weekend, and screw Valentine's Day. That's for all the people that don't have a loved one out there. They're miserable tomorrow. I understand. I was there. It sucks. E-Rock, what do you got? What?
See, the guy's buying himself Valentine's truffles. Sorry, E-Rock.
Why'd you just wave me off? What do you got?
Nothing. I'm fine.
Ooh. Well, talk to Opie that way. Hey, what is he, all of a sudden chopped tomatoes? Oh.
Are you gonna tell me a secret as soon as the mics go off?
Yes.
Not for air?
Yes.
Speculate. Blind CC.
Are you ready?
Da 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 da. Opie and Anthony. Well, I saw a lot go on as we left the other place to come over here. First of all, intern David, executive intern David, is very mad at Sam. We'll get into that in a second, but you know how we have to take all our shit every day and move it from one studio to the other?
We're vagabonds.
And we're the stars of the show, so we just put our coats on and leave. We don't have to fucking carry anything.
We have our coats put on us, you mean?
Oh, yeah. It's gotten to the point where actually Kenny will help us with our coats, yes. And then the interns have to grab all the equipment and the heavy shit and bring it from one studio to the other.
Gather it up.
And I'm watching this whole thing go down, and our lovely girl intern, the first woman intern we've had in a long time.
Jill.
Was carrying the heaviest fucking stuff.
That's the gentleman.
And intern David, Paul, right?
Yes.
Yeah, Paul goes, that's what I've been telling everyone. I'm like, what the fuck? Why are we? Because Paul was carrying his weight. Trust me, he had a huge bin too. And right behind him was the girl with the huge bin. I go, David, what the fuck? The girl's carrying the huge bin of stuff. And what did David say? David, you said what?
I said because she's a new intern and all the new interns have to start off carrying bins. Yes,
you,
I did.
You said to me.
Yes, I did.
Everyone has to carry something. Everyone's got to, what do you want from me? Everyone's got to carry something.
Right, that's what I meant.
Which sort of made sense until I saw what was in your hands that looked like it might have been a book. It might have been a book.
The whole first semester when I was here, I had to carry a bin all the time.
She's a woman!
She's a new intern. All the new interns have to carry bins for the whole first semester.
Faggot.
He's what?
You're just a fucking idiot.
Look, it's easy to go with, let her carry all the heavy shit.
Same thing with the idiot.
I want to go with another angle. Your parents didn't teach you how to treat women and ladies?
It has nothing to do with her personally. If it was any other girl, they would still have to carry a bin.
What the fuck's wrong with you?
Any other girl? This isn't the fucking Marines, dummy. Just because she's a member of the intern team,
right?
Of which you've self-anointed yourself as executive fucking...
I didn't self-anoint myself.
Yes, you did.
No,
shut up.
Didn't.
Who made you that?
Sam did.
Sam's a fucking... Sam is a sarcastic idiot who is goofing on you. Goofs on you.
I didn't make myself executive
Why
intern.
Would you allow...
Yes, you did.
No.
You acted stupid enough for Sam to realize he could put that title on you and you'd actually believe it. So you self-appointed yourself.
Sam, did you, as a goof, you appointed him executive intern, right? Maybe it's time to tell him.
David is executive intern because...
There's no such position!
Sure there is. He's
There's
a senior
not a
intern.
Position. No, he isn't.
That's how I see you. His position is senior intern.
Yes, there is.
How are you senior fucking intern?
Because I've been here longer than any other intern.
Yeah, who appointed you senior intern?
It just automatically becomes...
That's not in any rule book, you dummy!
I saw another intern called himself senior intern.
Attaboy.
Who? Hey, who called Ron called himself to me senior intern all the time. He always said he was a senior intern.
How is that?
Oh, shit.
How is that appointed? How does Sam appoint you senior intern?
Or executive.
Or executive
intern, which there is no such thing as executive intern. But he did, right?
He did, yes.
He did.
Yeah.
Who's bigger in this operation? Sam or me?
You.
Me.
Right.
You're out. You're now executive intern.
Disappear, scumbag.
All right.
Where are you pointing at?
That's it.
Oh, my God.
Who do you think he's pointing at, David?
Okay. He is now executive intern. You are just an intern now. You've been fucking demoted.
Okay, fine.
How does that feel?
No.
Fine.
And Sam can't do anything about it. No one else can. No one can override or veto this.
Okay.
I am the almighty fucking Führer.
Yes, you are.
And I say that you are just an intern. As a matter of fact, you're fucking bottom of the barrel, intern.
Oh.
She's fucking bigger than you right now.
Fine.
If she's carrying a heavy thing, you have every right, under my fucking jurisdiction, to say, hey, carry this. And he can't fucking say no, or you're out.
Hey, can I suggest something?
What?
I know you're the Führer and all, but how about we twist this a little bit and make her executive intern because of what happened today?
You're out. You are now executive intern.
How does that feel?
That
what's your name?
Me.
We don't even know
you
your name.
You can still
yet.
Put it on your resume, douchebag, so don't
right,
worry
right.
about it.
Right. What's your name?
I'm Jill.
Jill is now officially the executive intern
there
of the
you
Open
go.
Anthony. Sorry, Paul. I know you're trying, but you know.
If it had to be someone, I'd rather be.
All right. Because you understand
executive
how.
Intern.
You understand
what's
how
the matter?
Take
Jimmy's
care.
Got a problem.
Yeah. Not even a problem, just a question.
Yeah.
Did David really do anything wrong when he, in an act of corporate responsibility, treated all workers the same? Now, women complain. They don't want to be handled differently. They don't want to be treated as everyone else. And so David said, well, you're one of many. Pick up that bin hole and meet me over at the next joint.
You know what?
David treated her. He dictated.
That's all well and good, but we don't follow the corporate world in this environment. She's a skirt with some nice cans and stuff. And now we're making her executive intern because David didn't treat her like a woman.
But that's all. But if David would have treated her like a woman in a flirty way or whatever, we would say, David, you can't do that.
Oh, no.
So David's kind of between...
I'm all for, like, you know, giving a little pinch to the hiney and saying, way to go, toots. We still live in that world here, Jimmy, thank God. No offense to you, the fine female intern.
I don't know. I thought David was doing a good job barking out orders, taking no shit.
He was carrying a book, and he goes, well, we all got to carry something.
Good to be the boss.
And she's struggling with her little woman arms.
It's good to be the boss.
That haven't seen, you know, weights ever in her life.
Can I add something?
Oh, Paul wants to add something. Yes, Paul.
Okay. Ladies first.
See, that's how it goes, David.
Sexist.
That's what your parents should have taught you.
No, very sexist.
Ladies
very
first.
Sexist. All right.
Go ahead.
Well, today David found out that I was an eighth black, so I think it might be racially motivated.
You what?
You got black in
all right,
yeah.
You're out. You are executive intern.
Paul.
No.
By default, we're looking at the new executive intern,
no,
Paul.
People no just have to listen to 80% of what she says. So an eighth black. How did you come up with an eighth black?
Because my great-grandpa's black.
Your great-grandfather's black,
yeah.
Your great-grandma's happy?
The lightest kind, but yeah.
Let me take a look at
lightest kind of black?
Let's take a look at you under the lights. Get over here.
Do you fill that out on college applications and stuff?
It doesn't count. I don't make the...
What part of you is black?
Yeah, you don't look...
I don't know. It's mixed.
I don't think... Wow, that's...
What else
that's a great-grandfather black?
Yeah.
What
So your grandfather's father or your grandmother's father?
My grandpa's grandfather.
So your grandfather's father was black?
My grandma's father? Yeah, it gets hard.
Wait, your grandma's...
My grandma's father, yeah.
Father...
That's what it was.
...was black.
Mm-hmm.
So your great-grandmother was a size queen.
Tired of small colonial dicks.
Oh, yeah.
Basically.
Wanted some of that.
Look, when All the Way May was taking black collar...
All the Way
she
May.
She knew not to get pregnant.
That's by the way, it may only took
it
to shitter.
Fix it with an old Louisville slugger.
You know what this means?
Across the abdomen.
Penny Marshall with a bat and a hanger on the end of it.
You know what this means, right? Sam is so black.
Yeah. Oh,
dude,
yeah.
If she has a little black and you stop with the argument that you're not black.
You could use the N-word on the show with impunity.
Oh, absolutely.
That's how black you are.
Yeah. What do you do off here?
Sam, give us one.
No, I won't do
just
that.
Just give us one.
No, I've got
to... That's the rules. If you're black, you're allowed to say the N-word, so do it.
I want to represent the community properly if I'm going to represent
the
community.
Well, then do it with the IGGA thing.
I can't do that. That's not
Why?
Proper.
Why? That's safe.
It is?
No, it's not safe. You're not going to trick me.
It
certainly is safe.
I can't do this.
All right, who's the executive intern now, Ant? We got all sorts of issues here. David's out. Do we give it to the girl, or do we give it to Paul now?
Well, I got to give it to the girl, I guess.
All right. You're executive intern.
Yeah, I'll
I mean, show a little cleavage.
I've transcended some of my racism, even though she's, you know, whiter than I can't.
It's amazing, right?
What is
How
that?
Does that happen?
Jesus.
That's a little weird.
Yeah. So, I have to accept this under protest.
Why? You still think David should be?
We don't live in that corporate world. David, I understand what you're saying.
Not even the corporate world. I think even more than ever now, no disrespect to her, but more than ever,
yeah.
I think David has cemented his position as executive intern. He's not fucking hobnobbing around with the cute girl. He's carrying this shit. Me and my book are heading out.
She just unbuttoned a button, Jimmy. She knows how to play.
Oh, one button? Right. What is that?
She knows how to play.
Back in the game?
Yeah.
She heard you saying something, unbuttoned a button.
There you go.
I'll take the... Negro over the Jew.
Wow.
That's how I'm judging this.
David, you're out for a while, man. I don't know what to tell you. You disappointed me, man. She's fucking struggling down the hall with this huge bin, and David goes, we all got to carry something. If David had something that looked like he was actually carrying something, then maybe. I hear you have another problem with Sam today.
Yes, that is true.
I hear Sam and David had a falling out today.
No, because they're
all
the best. They're what I call asshole buddies.
Yeah. This all went down the last, 5 minutes of the other show.
What happened? Correct. David, what happened? You should be happy. The penthouse girls are coming in today. The one girl likes to hook up with an intern.
Mm-hmm.
When she's here, that's what she likes to do.
Mm-hmm. Correct.
So what's the problem? You should be psyched.
I was psyched for them. They're both coming.
Right, so what's the problem?
The problem is that at the end of the over at CBS, at the end of the show, when I was standing up doing something else and I was not looking, my jacket was sitting on a chair, and Sam over here proceeded to spray liquid A all over my jacket when I wasn't looking.
Yes, you could say liquid ass.
Liquid ass, yes, when I wasn't looking.
Liquid ass has made itself back, has brought itself back,
yeah?
It
rested for a while.
Brought back into the show.
He did not question me and say, is it okay if I spray liquid ass on your jacket, or I'm going to do it. He did it when I wasn't looking.
She won't even notice, man. What's that? Is that what you're worried about?
I am, no.
She ain't going to worry. She ain't going to notice.
No one's going to know now because I left the jacket over at CBS. I didn't bring it here.
Well, Stump Brain just called Steve and said, if somebody doesn't come get David's shit out of this office, I'm throwing it in the garbage.
And that's an expensive jacket.
Yeah.
Do I have to go back there and get it?
Yeah, you do.
A text that's coming in. Opie, from what you said before, ladies first. This coming from the guy who makes his wife freeze, watch him pick his nose, carry the heavy part of the Christmas tree, etc., etc., etc.
Don't forget the one I told today.
Yes.
The gas story.
The gas
and
deal with his
in a van.
Shit hoodies. Shit hoodie.
the good old shit hoodie.
Oh, my God.
Well, good point. You know, what can I tell you? By the way, because I know how this radio voodoo works, you were okay with everything we were just doing on the air?
Yeah.
Female intern?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right. I just wanted to get that out there.
I've
been doing radio long enough to understand how things get twisted, but yeah, we were just having fun with you, and you were cool with everything?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
All right. Thank you. You make our lives very easy by just saying that, trust me.
What happens if I say no? Do I get money?
We all masturbate.
You don't get money. Next thing you know, this stupid HR department gets their fucking hands involved in our show.
They want to have meetings. What
meetings
was said? What was done? Who was it?
Right.
It's all on the air.
It's all
if
on
anyone
the air
hassles you off the air, pinches your ass or something like that, you
then
know,
we
then,
have
then,
problems.
You, then there's a problem,
right?
Right.
Yeah. Right.
If you don't smack on your ass.
Trust me, I just saved us probably 6 hours of problems.
Meetings?
Yeah, just because these dopes think they know what radio's all about. All right, so David, you're not happy with Sam.
No.
You want to have it out with Sam a little bit? Are you guys through, you think?
Go get him.
I don't know. I'm wondering if anyone's going to get the jacket. Someone has to go get it, I think.
I agree, David. You ought to dictate that result. Oh.
No, I can't dictate.
That's right.
No, that's right, Jimmy.
Oh, when you were
I appreciate
executive.
You, though, Jimmy. You stood up for me.
Sure did. David,
that's very nice of you.
The executive.
He's been on a...
I think I have to get it myself. I can't designate.
He's been on a self-destructive journey. He's isolated
Gates,
his friendship with Kenny. He's not friends with Kenny anymore.
Why aren't you friends with Kenny?
Kenny loves you.
Kenny buys you breakfast every morning.
But...
not anymore.
No.
What happened, Kenny?
There was a falling out?
Oh, here comes Kenny.
You two were like two peas in a pod.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Two J's in a pod.
Look at David just shaking his head, looking at the ground. Sam. Why are you doing this, Sam? Why? What's that about, David?
David's crashing and burning.
What happened with you and David?
Well, Wednesday I delegated a specific task to David, and he failed to complete that task.
What was
it? Uh-oh.
He was supposed to, when your coffee pot lights up in the morning, pour your coffee. And within the 5 minutes it took for the coffee to percolate, David forgot all about it and just decided to go on the internet and look up whatever he looked up.
Oh, boy.
Kenny, I gotta say, maybe David did forget, but perhaps he was doing some kind of show prep and he got carried away. And you can't fault the man for working hard for the radio program and forgetting something like that.
James, let's not be confused here. Nothing is more important than GH when it comes to his coffee.
Fair enough. I don't even disagree.
And I was wondering why I had a bad show Wednesday. I'll start with the coffee.
Oh, David.
Coffee was bad. It threw me off.
That'll do it.
And then Sam was trying to get David to apologize to me and reconcile.
Right.
And for whatever reason, David is refusing to reconcile.
Why won't you, try to get nice with Kenny?
I apologize.
I'm not mad. I'm just hurt.
Right away when he told me that I forgot to do, and I realized that I forgot to do, 10 times, I said, oh, man, I forgot I did. I'm sorry. I apologize.
Yeah.
Right away I did.
But now you don't like Kenny.
I did apologize right away.
But you don't like him.
I never said I don't like him.
And then in turn you stopped buying him breakfast?
He didn't talk to me all day today.
I did not like him. I apologized.
Confused.
Oh, boy. All right. And now what's the problem with Sam?
And now he's accusing me of things which there's no real evidence of.
Yeah.
You know, nobody saw me pour liquid ass on his jacket. Maybe his jacket just happens to smell like shit.
That is not the case at all, no. It didn't smell like that when I came here this morning, no.
You're very disappointed with Sam, huh? David, speak your mind.
Well, according to Sam, it wasn't him. I don't know. If you believe Sam, then someone else is at fault.
Yeah.
I believe it was Sam, because Sam is the only one that has access to the little bottle of liquid ass.
He's the keeper of the liquid ass?
He certainly is the keeper, yes.
No one else.
He is the keeper. And
what's that about? No one else is allowed that the liquid ass, Sam?
Well, I mean, I just kind of wanted to fall into the wrong hand.
Exactly.
Right?
You gave me that responsibility of making sure it didn't fall into the wrong hand. You said, Sam, make sure this doesn't fall into the wrong hands.
Nice. All right.
So.
anybody out there want to smell the liquid ass? You've heard about it. You want to smell it? Who wants in? David, why don't you work the crowd with the liquid ass? Ask who wants to smell it.
Okay, that's what you say. That's what I'll do. Okay.
Well, is that okay with the executive input?
Oh, okay.
You want David to do that?
I think David should maybe apologize to Sam for accusing him.
Oh,
that's a good idea.
Shit.
Why should I apologize to Sam? He poured the liquid ass on my jacket. I don't need to apologize. I didn't do anything wrong.
You've got a problem with authority, David. That's the big thing here.
I'm apologizing for something that someone else did to my jacket.
Yes, Paul.
If I could interject one second. There was also a slight incident with Kenny last week when Kenny asked David to go get, you know, their daily muffins, as he's, you know, usually buys them breakfast. And David looked at him and said, well, Kenny, why don't you just go and get the muffins?
I'm sure not without reason. David, why would you tell Kenny to go get the muffins?
I told him because he was on his way out already to move Anthony's car to the parking garage. So when he was already going to...
Yeah,
absolutely. So when he was already going to do that, I just said, well, if you're out already, why don't you just go get him? Because he's done that in the past. When he's gone out to move Anthony's car, he's gone in the past and got this muffin.
Sure. While the task doer is out doing a task, throw one more. I completely agree.
Yes. Correct. I didn't see that was a problem at all.
You're right.
All right. Hey, people want to know if David's allowed to work the crowd still. He's not the executive intern anymore.
That's true. Wow.
Am I?
But David does a good job at that,
so he could do that. That's something a lowly intern would do.
Oh, yeah.
We might not have time for your bit today, David.
Well,
you
want me to go out there and ask him about the liquid A?
Yeah, we could at least do that real fast.
What is
liquid
ass?
Liquid ass. I'm trying to get
is that against your religion? Against your religion?
No, it's not. I'm trying to ask them who wants to smell the liquid ass.
Yeah.
Don't
squirt on anyone.
Who would want to be squirted with it?
No, don't squirt nobody. You take the cap off and they get a little sniff of the liquid ass.
Okay. It doesn't work out of the bottle like that. It's got to be on some. Remember, it needs to be exposed to the air.
Maybe we put it on like a shirt sleeve of
some type of porous material.
Do you want me to report back to you on what the reactions were?
David, I want you to put a little on your shirt sleeve because that's the best way to smell the liquid ass.
Don't worry, David. I just put a pinch on.
A little pinch.
Here's a pinch.
And then you want me to report on what people's reactions were?
Yes,
no,
please
then
don't.
You work the crowd and go, who wants to smell the liquid ass? And when they raise their hand like, ooh, me, because everybody wants to, then they smell your sleeve.
Right, and you want to know what their reactions are.
Yes.
We'll get the reaction, because you're going to have a microphone.
Okay, just a pinch, Sam.
Yeah.
Just a pinch.
You spray a lot.
A pinch.
No,
between your cheek and gum.
Sam, just a pinch.
Right, just to get your sleeve.
No, I agree that David...
Okay,
Sam, just do it. David, I actually...
Oh, my!
What happened? The bottle is broken.
Yeah, the bottle must be broke.
David, what happened?
Well, if that's the case, I'm not going to do it. I wasn't forewarned about this.
No, huh?
But you have it on you, so you might as well now.
Yeah, now, you know.
How bad is the smell?
Probably not bad. Ass and make ass aid.
How bad is the smell?
It's on the sleeve. It's on the sleeve.
There you go.
All right. Does it smell bad?
Yes, it does.
Yeah, it smells really, really bad.
All right, now go and work the crowd.
Oh, is that his ass jacket?
Oh, no, look who it is.
No, don't wreck his jacket. That wouldn't be...
Oh, what's the matter? Look who it is? What do you mean?
Look who it is. Joe brings the jacket. Uh-oh.
Joe has his own issues.
You have a problem with Joe?
Well, no, I just have a problem with someone bringing the jacket back. Anyone would have a problem. I don't want this jacket.
You're really stupid, because if you said I have a problem with Joe, then Ant would have liked you, because Ant has a problem with Joe.
Does he?
Well,
yeah,
I did.
Something in common.
We kind of, you know, I don't hold a grudge like David does.
No kidding,
David holds a grudge like,
But the irony is that since Joe brought back David's jacket, and it was already sprayed before, we didn't even have to spray David.
I know,
no.
Crazy how that
happens? So weird.
Now the jacket, and isn't it weird, the jacket came in seconds after David was sprayed with much too much liquid ass.
That's crazy.
From that broken bottle,
isn't
I
it?
Guess.
Yeah, it's malfunctioning.
All right, David, you got the microphone, you got the liquid ass on your sleeve. We're getting ready for Taya Parker and Shauna Linnea.
Linnea?
How do you say her last name?
I'm going to guess.
We know Linnea. Taya came in here as penthouse pet of the year. I tried fucking with her, and it turned out she was very cool and did everything we asked. And she has come back. And I guess her videos are a huge hit online. They're everywhere. And she's on Rock of Love Bus, or whatever it's called this time around. She's great.
Rock of Love Bus?
Rock Bus? Rock of Love Bus, yes.
It is, right?
I actually got vibes from her.
Really? Taya?
No.
Oh. Well, it wouldn't be the first time. Why is that a surprise?
I was kidding. I got none.
Whatever happened with that one?
It was wonderful.
And then you moved on?
No.
Because people still ask.
She did.
She moved on.
Well, no, she lives wherever she lives.
Yeah, all right. David!
But it went well.
Very good. David!
I made...
Yes?
All right, work the crowd. You got the liquid ass. Now, take the mic from Sam.
I almost came in her. I love you.
Oh, my God. What's wrong with you? Fucking Jimmy. Nice. All right, David, why don't you work the crowd? You got the mic.
All right.
The stage is you. All right. Could turn up his mic a little bit. That would be nice.
Yeah, and the crowd mic, too.
I haven't heard the crowd mic too well today, either. You're right, Jimmy.
Can the crowd say something?
Hello!
Hey. Is that on or no?
Yeah. It doesn't really sound like it's on.
No, it sounds like it's coming through the door. Sam, is that on? Say something to the mic.
Tap the mic.
Testing.
Okay, yeah, it's on.
All right.
All right. David, go ahead. Do your job.
All right.
Introduce yourself. Say hi to everybody.
Hello. I'm intern David. What's your name?
I'm Adam from Jersey.
Adam, nice to meet you. Have you ever smelled liquid ass before?
I have not.
Would you care to smell my sleeve?
Yeah,
that's pretty bad. That's pretty bad.
Would you like us to spray you with some liquid ass?
Jesus.
No? All right.
No liquid ass for me, thank you.
Okay.
Oh my God.
Hey, what's up? I'm intern David. Your name is?
Hey man, I'm Chris from Phoenix City, Alabama.
Have you ever smelled liquid ass before?
I have not.
Would you like to smell my sleeve?
Why not?
It's filled with liquid ass.
Sure. Bring it
on. All right, here you go.
It's filled with liquid ass.
Oh.
What do you think of that smell?
You smell like shit, David.
Would you care to be smelled with liquid ass?
No.
I mean sprayed.
Smelled with it?
Sprayed.
No, I don't want to be sprayed with it.
No?
No.
All right. Thank you for smelling, though. We appreciate it. Hello, I'm intern David. What's your name?
I'm Tony.
Where are you
so
from,
bad.
Tony?
From Phoenix City.
Phoenix City?
Yeah.
Have you ever smelled liquid ass before?
No.
Would you like to smell my sleeve? It's filled with liquid ass.
Not really.
No, why not? Do it for the radio show. Well, we want to see your reaction.
I smell it from here.
You do?
I think you're pretty well
I think
covered.
You want to smell.
I think you're covered. That's awful.
I think you're covered.
It,
what do you think of that smell?
It smells like ass. It's
would you care
ass.
To be sprayed with liquid ass?
No.
No? Oh, all right. Hello, I'm intern David. What's your name?
Matt.
Where are you from, Matt?
Poughkeepsie.
Have you ever been, smelled liquid ass before?
No,
would you like to smell my sleep? It's covered in liquid ass.
Sure.
All right, here you go.
My shit don't smell that bad.
Nah.
Actually, no, mine smells worse.
Yours? What are you talking about? Are you covered in liquid ass?
No.
Oh, your shit smells worse, maybe?
Yeah.
If it doesn't smell that bad, would you like us to cover you in liquid ass and you see how it works?
Not particularly.
But I thought you said it doesn't smell bad.
Ooh.
Yeah, but I have to sit on the train all the way home.
Oh.
Which would give me my own seat.
What if it doesn't
So does David.
What if it doesn't smell bad, then what's the worst that could happen? If it doesn't smell bad, then you wouldn't mind being covered in it, would you?
He's hard.
Sure.
Oh, I know. That's why we're doing this.
Yeah?
Sam, he would like to
Hooray!
We'd like to get
you comfortable. We have our first customer.
Why are you... He really wants to be sprayed with it?
He said he doesn't mind. He said he doesn't mind.
Yeah, all right.
He's not reacting. He's not. He says
that's fine.
It's not bothering him.
Yeah, give it a moment or two.
A little in the hood.
Yeah. Sam, is it starting to smell out there?
Yeah,
this smell is horrendous.
Thank you so much. You're a good sport.
All right, David.
A good sport.
David, you don't have to work. Just ask who else wants to smell this. Let's get this
We're
over
going
with.
Going down to everyone in the walk.
No, that'll take forever. Right. There's like 50 people here today.
All right,
but your heart's in the right place, David.
Yes, it is. I agree.
How about one big announcement? Who wants to smell my sleeve?
All right. Hello, I'm intern David. Who would like to smell my sleeve? It's covered in liquid ass. Does anyone want to smell it? Anybody at all? Do you have any takers?
Yeah, I'll take a little bit, David.
All right, step right up.
Step right up. It's like it's something good.
Yeah.
Hello. What's your name?
John.
Where are you from, John?
From Boston.
Have you ever smelled liquid ass before?
I'm from Boston.
So what does that mean?
He elected it mayor.
My sleeve is covered in liquid ass. Would you like to smell it?
Sure, Davis.
All right, here you go.
All right. Oh. It's almost like a horse shit or something.
Yeah, it's pretty accurate.
Thank you, David.
Oh, you're very welcome.
With a little baby shit mixed in.
Yeah.
Do you have any other takers? Would anybody else like to smell? All right, come on down.
Oh, look at that.
Unfortunately, this is going to be the last one. I know this bit's killing
it.
We got
destroying.
Other things we got to do.
Hello, I'm intern David. What's your name?
I'm Ben from Albany.
Ben from Albany. Have you ever smelled liquid ass before?
Not yet.
Would you like to smell my sleeve? It's covered in liquid ass.
One time only. Let's go.
One time? All right, here you go. What do you think of that smell?
It's like liquid swamp ass.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Pretty much.
All right.
Thank you, David.
Thank you, and I want to just give a thank you to the fan that covered himself in liquid A. That's very nice.
Liquid ass, David. Liquid you would say
ass. Liquid
say
ass, it. Yes.
God,
ass.
I wish it was called liquid cunt.
Liquid ass, yes.
Just so we'd have to say that.
Yes.
All right, David.
Good job, as always.
Yeah, that was
thank you so much.
That was just amazing, David. Right up there with some of your other appearances. We're going to take a quick break, and we're going to... Is Taya here?
Yes.
Oh, they're here.
Mm-hmm.
And Shauna, how do you say her last name? People are...
I'm guessing Lene.
Yeah, that's what it is. Yeah.
People are psyched that she's here. They're like, wow, she's a goer. This one is a live one.
Well, we have one of
Taya's a live one.
We have one of Shauna's Penthouse Presents movies, Bring Me the Head of Shauna Lene. I'm wondering if this is hardcore fucking.
Oh, yeah?
It looks like yours. I see a big penis.
Ooh.
I'm trying to see what she looks like, Jimmy.
She's on the cover. She's lovely.
Holy shit.
Yes.
All right, we'll continue in just a bit. Opie and Anthony.
Welcome back.
Yeah.
To the Opie and Anthony radio program. Anthony's chewing, Opie is tinkling.
Opie's making wee-wees.
And we have the two girls from Penthouse, Taya Parker and Shauna Lene. Hopefully they're coming in.
And they're going to walk into this stench palace because that liquid ass was... excuse the smell in here. It isn't us. It's liquid ass, it's called.
Yeah, why wouldn't you put it's one horrible. Of each mic, E-Rock? What are you doing?
What?
I don't know.
Oh, thanks a lot, you cock-blocking motherfucker, Jimmy Norton.
That wasn't me. I didn't ask him.
You told her to move.
No, I was saying one on each mic.
Yeah, one, two. And then dummy moves him over. I got nothing sitting next to me now. Why don't you put David in the fucking seat next to me? I'll grope his dick.
I meant...
Ugh, I'm tired of this shit.
I meant one there.
Fuck this.
I thought he was putting...
Sorry, ladies.
He's having a mental breakdown over there.
Oh, always.
I thought E-Rock was putting two people on one microphone, so I'm like, why don't you put one there?
That would be silly.
Yeah, I know.
I don't get to fucking see and get the nice fragrance off of girls.
Yeah, I think this should
I gotta
be...
fucking get... Oh, every...
How
guys,
about
get away from me. I'm sick of guys.
Do you want David here?
How about...
I want David there if I could kick him out the window.
We should have... Why can't we have one girl... Because Anthony's upset. Why can't we have
no,
one
no, it's
there?
Charity.
No, it's not. It's important. Plus, yeah, they can see Opie better if they're talking to him.
Wow-wee.
I don't care.
Wow-wee.
Okay, don't mind me. Just a little crazy.
What happened, Ant?
What happened?
Nothing. One of the girls are going to sit here. Yeah. And one was going to sit there.
Yeah.
What's wrong with that?
And then there was some mix-up between E-Fat and Cockblock and Jim.
But no, I didn't.
And they both wind up sitting over there.
Do you want me to come sit over there?
Yeah, sit over there.
I'm totally going over there to sit. I don't even care. I'm going to be insubordinate.
E-Rock put two chairs there. So I thought, why is he having two girls on one mic? It's silly.
Right.
So I said, why do you have...
That's better.
Yeah.
What the fuck? I just wanted to smell better than the liquid ass that's in here. And, you know, girls, it stinks in this. You know why? Is it a little dropper bottle of something called liquid ass that everyone thinks is hysterical until it wafts over your way.
Could we give her a booster seat at least?
I know. I feel like I'm like in the kiddie section.
Yeah.
I have to.
Oh, Uncle Paul.
Bad enough, I'm like 4'11".
Yeah, give her another seat. Tell you, I'm gonna do something that is gonna be very unusual. I think Ant's only seen this once or twice. I'm gonna apologize to you.
You're gonna apologize to me?
Yeah, because last time you came in, I was thinking I'm just gonna mess with her, and I was an asshole, and I threw everything I had at you, and you were cool as shit.
Stop it! You don't have to apologize to me.
And then even after the show, I'm like, oh, you know, it was for the radio. Just you know.
It's your show. You can beat me up if you
no,
want.
No, but it wasn't fair. I mean, usually we beat the shit out of people. We, you know.
have a problem with. So.
That's okay, honey.
You ended up doing like backwards flips into guys' faces, and
it was amazing.
It was amazing shit you were doing
this
for everybody.
Jumping through hoops, and I'm just being mean.
And then our good friend Brett Michaels comes in and goes, "This Taya chick is, you know, is the real deal. She's awesome."
Oh, did he say nice things about her?
Absolutely, he did.
Aw, how sweet.
And you were, are you still on the show?
I'm still on the show right now. Yeah.
See, I haven't watched the show yet.
It's 5 episodes in.
Okay. Yeah. And were you doing the drinking out of the puss?
Oh, why does everybody think?
I don't know, because I haven't seen it yet.
And I'm like, I wasn't even anywhere near that when it was going on. It was two blondes. I don't even understand how it could have possibly been confusing to me.
Everyone is saying that you were part of that.
Absolutely not. Yeah. Never in a million years.
Were you just pouring the liquid? Nothing?
I wasn't even near it. It was two blondes. That's why I'm kind of confused about the confusion, because I'm clearly not a blonde, so I don't understand why everybody thought that was me from your show.
Problem.
You know what? It's okay. I mean, anytime I'm involved in controversy, especially if it's not true, I'm all about that.
Right on. Okay.
Does Brett have a big penis?
Oh, my God.
I'm not gay at all. I happen to like him a lot, and he comes in a lot, and this is why he's a big penis.
Have you seen his penis?
I have not.
Come on. You need to catch a glimpse of it, like, by accident?
Catch a glimpse of it? I mean, it's he's got quite a manly bulge down there.
Yeah. He's a rock star.
He looks like he's hung perfectly well.
Nah, they do a little padding or something, probably. No.
I have Bruce Dickinson as a huge penis from Iron Maiden, because we've always met the Iron Maiden poster. All right.
We're like, this is just
Jimmy
weird.
Just likes talking about men's penises.
That's not true at all. I was trying to get the girls all riled up.
We have got to turn this conversation around immediately.
You brought your friend Shauna today.
I did. Isn't she cute?
Now, you guys fought it out for Pet of the Year?
We didn't fight it out. We loved it out.
You technically lost to Taya, right? I think you could have went either way, though, here.
No, I mean, a competition. It's not. Honestly, she is. I mean, she's 21 years old. The world is her oyster.
Jesus,
I'm 30. So we're like at opposite ends of the spectrum. She's there and got many years to go. So she's amazing.
Is this out of line? I'm seeing a girl right now.
Is this out of line?
But if there's any shot, I would decapitate her for you.
Oh, goodness. That's not out of line at all.
No, not at all. Not
Every
at all.
Girl loves to hear that a man would decapitate his girlfriend for her.
Yeah.
Oh, right on, Jimmy. Good.
Yeah, she's got that cute look, they call it.
The cute look.
Girl next door. Very
cute all the time.
Yeah.
I really don't like that word. I don't like it.
You know something? You're stuck with it, I think.
Well, you got the dimples.
It's those little dimples and everything and the little blue eyes.
Besides those
adorable.
Amazing tits, you got those dimples that are so adorable.
Yeah.
I like your two dimples.
It is, and it's the big smile. It's like, you know, it's like very, it is very cute.
Oh.
Yeah, look like you could be abducted walking home from high school.
I've almost been abducted before.
Almost?
Really?
On the lucky devil.
I pepper sprayed him.
Yeah.
Wait,
this was only 6 months ago.
Holy shit, what happened?
Me and my girlfriend at the time, she was even younger than me. She was only 19. We're at a gas station, and this guy, like, literally climbs in our car, and I pepper sprayed him. He was like, "How old are you?" And she said, she's an idiot, though. She opened the door for him.
What an idiot.
Don't open a door for a guy you don't know. So...
And how'd you get the pepper spray out of your eyes?
It wasn't very difficult.
Actually, I kind of got my girlfriend, but it didn't hurt
collateral damage.
You're like, close your mouth, close your eyes, I'm spraying him. It's going down.
Yeah, right? It wasn't fun, and it was like right near the place I was living at.
You'd have been getting sprayed in the face. That's not anything to toy with. Oof. That hurt.
We don't know what's going on.
I'm trying
today.
To find your line of humor here, and I'm failing miserably.
That was my favorite moment in him, because I'm looking at Anthony, and I can't see his mouth. All I can see is hat and eyes.
I know, and a bomb.
What happened?
I tried to make a joke about, somebody sexually assaulting somebody and maybe jism flying in their face instead
of
pepper spray.
Thank you for clarifying that for the rest
of the
room.
I like really getting blunt and to the point on a story and a joke bomb.
It's okay.
So, Penthouse, huh?
Penthouse.
Yeah.
She's on stands right now. Everybody needs to pick it up.
What?
It's crazy naughty.
On stands now. I'm on the cover, March 2009.
You're on the cover? Is that it?
This is me.
Yeah, that's it. Hoard them all over there.
I've seen it already.
Alrighty.
But I'll let you touch it if you're good.
Thank you.
I'll let you touch
it. Let me look. Wow.
Isn't she adorable?
Holy.
How cute am I in that picture?
That's,
That goes past cute.
Yeah.
Thank you.
That's absolutely not the first word that comes to mind when I see that.
Do you take cute as, like, not insulting, but as not...
I take it as insulting.
Because you want it to be sexy or hot, not cute.
Don't worry,
cute is, little girlish to you?
Yeah, cute is way too little girlish for me. Like, I like...
Honey, embrace the cute.
I don't mean
cute.
Like that.
No, I like older men, and it really freaks me out when they call me cute.
You're cute in a JonBenet really Ramsey kind of way.
Yeah, see?
That's not great either.
I'm teasing, of course. Wow. Like a Dakota Fanning.
Everything just got really creepy.
I know. This is what I go through every day, Tam.
Yeah.
That's being creeped out.
Taya, what are you waiting for? Get her clothes off, will you?
You want me to get her clothes off?
Yeah, man.
I'm totally
not
capable of
myself. I have to bear all the burden of responsibility every time I come in here.
She might follow your lead. I'm
thinking. I feel so stressed out right now. Shauna, take off your clothes.
Let's play a little
seriously. I was completely.
Let's play a little game of chicken. You take a piece off.
Chicken.
You take a piece off, then she takes. And then let's see how far we can get this. Wow.
Opie just sits there and stirs the pot. I love it.
Yes.
He's a pot stirrer.
Mm. Wow. Oh, okay.
These all right, Taya will take
very,
her
very nice.
You guys want to see Taya take her shirt off?
Yeah.
No, that's icky.
No,
why would you suggest that, Opie and Anthony?
That's so bad.
Wow.
Oh. We're like, are you serious?
I know. I'm like,
what's wrong with taking your clothes off?
You got a boyfriend or anything?
No, I do not have a boyfriend. I am single as single could be.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, we're scouting around some options.
Do you use your singularity? Do you just use it? Do you, I'm single and I don't see anybody or anything?
No, I would love to see somebody.
Yeah.
I just haven't found that right guy yet.
What, are you looking for a guy with a movie theater in his basement kind of a guy? And shit like that? Pool in a jacuzzi? Is that what you're looking for?
No.
Just asking, just randomly asking.
I'm looking for a guy that's not jealous about my job.
You do hardcore?
Yes.
Cool. What if
but I don't want to date in the industry. So
what if he's
that a problem? That's a problem with some guys?
Oh, yeah.
Are you kidding?
I'll date a guy for like
a week,
and then it'll turn into, okay, well, you have to quit your job for me because I just can't handle it.
Wow, that's insanity.
And that's only
it attracts
one
them,
of,
and
like,
then once they get you,
20.
It's like, I can't take it.
Yeah.
It is tough, though. I mean, to date, I've dated a little bit in that. It is difficult if you really just fall for somebody.
I couldn't imagine getting jealous over something like that.
Anthony certainly wouldn't get jealous.
Amazing.
Over that. Ooh, her eyes just perked up a little bit.
But if somebody's
lying
having...
through my fucking teeth, I'd lock her in a closet.
Yeah, it's hard because the banging guy's like fucking Manuel Ferrara.
Yeah, and then what are you going to come up with?
Yeah. Nothing. He's in better shape.
Hope this works, honey.
Yeah, that makes it very difficult for me.
Does it? You're a size queen? You like the big...
I do.
Yeah?
I've always liked the big ones ever since the first time.
But you need a guy to bottom out?
Well, what's up with the lady saying...
I'm your man.
What's up with the lady saying, it's not the size?
You know what? Honestly,
it's
for
lie.
Me, it's not. Like, no. I've...
Well, you're a tiny little thing.
I actually have run scared from guys with big thingies.
Yeah.
I'm like, you're not touching me with that.
Like that.
I'm out of here.
This would be way more interesting if you guys were naked. I got it.
I do kind of agree. I mean,
Jimmy, are you with me?
Yeah, because there's a lovely... Look at the lovely
it's
crowd.
It's so weird, but I become...
If I take my top off, will you be nice to me this time?
Yeah, I become a much better listener when the girl's naked. It's
she's sitting there, like, zoning out, like, I'm sorry.
Wait, aren't you guys the stock ticker?
Ears perk
point.
Up when I see
you
breasts.
Are both doing an appearance today, correct?
We are at the Romantic Depot.
What's that?
In New Jersey, from noon to 2.
At Paramus. Getting carjacked.
Jeez. Oh, stop it. We love that place. Everybody comes
out. The
they're
place,
so great.
The Paramus is a little weird.
Yeah.
Well, it takes weird people to want to come and see us and drive all that way. Last time I was there in a snowstorm and people were there. I'm like, you people love me and I love it.
They love, nude girls.
All right, Shauna.
Okay, here we go.
Unleash the beast.
All right.
I put on a bra and everything. This is so high maintenance.
How inconvenient.
It is.
I have
so
a brand new bra on today.
Sweet
number
pants.
One, it's all lacy. You guys are going to love it.
All purdy.
Mine's not. I have to go straight for, like, conventional. I need my girls to be stabilized.
Stabilized.
They don't make pretty bras in size huge boobs.
Size huge boobs. I've never heard that size.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Wow.
Yeah, those are boobs.
Are you guys
yeah.
happy now?
Yeah.
Wow.
See, that's... Oh, that
seriously.
Is a nice, very pretty green... Forest green.
Look at her.
You know what's awesome about this bra?
It's that you're going to take it off.
There are hot tits under it.
It's
wow.
Little lips on the
that's
inside.
fucking ludicrous.
So my nipples are being kissed at all times.
They are very, if you don't mind me saying that, they are rather large, like very protruding, lovely nipples.
Very protruding.
They could poke somebody's eye out.
They are lovely. Very perk. Pert. Very pert nips.
Okay, this makes me feel a little, like, naked.
Just a little,
too. Yes, you are a little naked.
It's making me feel a little uncomfortable.
No.
Why? Because we got a big audience today?
Well, no. I'm fine with audiences, but it's just weird trying to talk serious when you're like, boobs are out. Stop looking at my boobs. Listen to what I have to say. It's so smart.
Oh, boy. Aunt?
Opie, yes. Are you listening now?
What happened?
Excuse me, are you listening?
I am. I want you to do something for the
if you're not listening,
though.
I'm putting my shirt back on.
I certainly am. I got a couple things going on here right now, though.
You don't have anything going on.
I want one of you girls to, like, rub your, like, boobs up against the glass. Kind of like, if you're old school, like Kentucky Fried movie. In the shower.
Probably Catholic high school girls in trouble?
Thank you, Anthony.
Yeah,
For
the listeners, because they got their cameras and everything. You push them up against the window and make them look silly.
Is it like a photo op?
Yeah. We keep them there.
I don't know if I want everybody taking pictures of my titties.
Yeah, right.
Honestly.
We keep them there like the caged chimps that they are. They have no joy in life other than the bosoms of our guests, Tony Rock.
What?
Could you push your boobs up against the glass?
You guys are just totally...
I'll sexy it up. I'll push my ass cheeks against the window if you push your breasts against the
glass. Really?
Of course I will.
Your bare ass? I think that's a deal.
Jimmy laughs at that stuff. That's easy for
bare
him.
Bare ass?
Of course. What else is there?
You'll take your bare ass out and put it up against that window.
Yeah, his greasy
fucking
bare
faster
ass.
Faster than I'll breathe.
Get
I'll
that bare ass out before I get up, because I'm not going to get all up and what, start...
Oh, no, he'll do it. He's not going to fucking...
Oh, shut
he's
up.
He's not backing out on anything. Jimmy is a trooper.
Jimmy, I want to get a picture of this.
Hold on.
Jimmy's
a picture,
trooper,
Jimmy.
Man.
Hold on. Those poor people.
Just, you're going to have to edit the
those
log.
Those poor people.
I feel bad.
There you go.
And they're taking pictures.
Oh, yeah, they love it. It's Jimmy's ass. Jimmy's a famous TV, radio, and book star.
Okay, is that good? One more? Believe my ass is pressed against us right now. Get those dicks out, fellas.
I love it. He's cracking me up. Okay, I will go press my boobs against the glass for like 15 seconds.
And make like,
you're coming with.
And no,
make,
thanks.
And make balloon noises.
How about just your hiney? You push your hiney
against. I am not a monkey. No, you like, make noises.
Aunt.
What?
You remember the scene, but you have to make balloon noises.
All you have to do
is press up against the glass and just...
I think we could add that in later.
Monkey, jump through this hoop.
Right, yeah, exactly.
All right, we'll do the sound effects. You just do the pushing of the boobs. Here's Taya, everyone.
We'll push the boobs.
Okay.
Here. Up against.
There it is.
Push.
I'm not making the noise, Opie.
No.
So how did you guys like that?
Yeah.
But you have to admit, my ass was a little better against the window than you thought it would be.
Hey, your ass against the window was better than...
They were surprisingly...
Everything.
You know.
Yeah, I think there's not a man out there that didn't notice the smoothness of it. The contour
of it. No hair.
Exfoliate?
Hairless.
No, I just have very smooth hiney. I've always had that. Mm-hmm. Very lucky boy.
I think you
exfoliate. Men love it.
Oh, you
I
look do, like I actually, an exfoliator to me.
I use one of those things, those fucking...
A loofah?
Yes.
Good boy.
What's a loofah?
I like a man that uses a loofah. So, Opie, you're not paying attention.
What?
You're not paying attention to me.
Out. I get bored.
What?
Easy.
How'd you get into the business?
Me. I got into the business.
Why are they putting their clothes back?
Because I just pressed my boobs against the glass over there. I have to maintain some sort of class here.
Give him a boo, guys.
You guys can't boo me. I just showed you
fucking
my boobs.
Fucking ingrates,
don't
man.
Don't you boo me.
Fucking ingrates.
Don't you boo me. You guys yay me right now. Yay. Yay me.
Yay me.
See if I ever show you my boobs ever again.
How about we all sit
you're
in our underpants?
You're going to have to get magazines to see them.
Let's sit in our underpants and socks.
Hey, Taya, can you...
socks? I don't have any socks on.
Taya, can you ass cave the glass for everybody?
Do what?
Ass cave.
Like gaping?
You know
or?
What?
I opened my cheeks a little against the glass.
Yeah, Jimmy did.
Yeah.
I'm like 30 seconds away from breaking up with you. Publicly.
Oh,
on the radio.
Oh, shit.
Damn.
All right, sorry.
So
I was just asking how she got in the business, being such a young girl.
I got into the business when I was 18 and 5 days old, and it was what I always wanted to
She said 18
really?
And 5 days.
So, yes. Like,
that's so
oh,
cute.
I didn't hear the 18
so
part.
You're like, oh. Uncle Paul.
You just said the 5 days?
So
18 and 5 days.
So, you know, it's right after your 18th birthday. You always wanted to do it?
Yeah. Well, not always, but
until
for a
when?
Few years.
I mean, since, like, what? How old?
12.
Really?
Yes.
You knew at 12?
At 12, yeah. You knew you wanted to take your clothes off for people.
Yes.
And how is that?
I discovered internet porn at the age of 12.
Yeah.
Internet porn.
I love internet porn.
Who was the first porn guy you looked at? Or who's one porn guy you looked at when I really want to fuck him?
Oh, no, I looked at girls.
Yeah, girl looking at girls.
All right, who?
First.
No. I love naked girls.
Well, who did you look
we
at?
We have so much in common.
I don't even know their names. I know. I mean, I wasn't
again.
Like
we have
a
so much in common.
Fan.
It didn't really matter.
A 12-year-old porn fan. More in common than you thought.
I mean, I didn't know their names. That wasn't one of my priorities to know.
So now, what was your first gig at 18 and 5 days?
It was for Joy Silvera's service. This is a horrible title. There's
service
no,
animals.
Yes.
Animals
is great. Service animals number 21. No animals were involved. Thank yeah. you guys.
What you did?
I did a regular boy girl scene. I was totally dressed as a really young girl with pigtails and
of course
pink. She's gonna be able to play the really young girl forever.
No, I don't play it and they don't hire me anymore because I'm not a teenager. Most companies are guaranteed teens.
Oh yeah.
So as soon as I hit 20 I cried and was like oh.
Fuck
you
over the hell.
Retire at 20
from the teen porn. Yeah,
yeah.
Wow.
Who would you do the scene with?
She blew
you know,
out
it was this guy. It was this guy named Trent. I don't even know what happened to him. It was actually one of his first scenes too.
Oh yeah. And what you before your breast enhancement? Were you very small?
I had nothing.
So you really pulled off the kid thing?
Yeah, I hated it.
Yeah. I had fabulous boobs. I wish I would have never gotten my boobs done.
That's
a big mistake.
Why? Well,
did
you have?
I mean, don't get me wrong. I'm happy with
nice
them.
Nice natural ones.
I had awesome boobs. I don't know what I was thinking. I think, you know, I was from this really small town, and I thought, if I'm going to be in the adult industry, this is what I need to do.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't even research doctors or anything. So the bad thing is that I got my boobs done by this guy that basically did everybody. No, he was, you know, but he was like the only guy in that area that really did the surgery. And I didn't even realize I had a bad boob job until I started seeing pictures. And I'm like, that just doesn't seem right.
Oh, boy.
And so I had to get them redone. But it's so funny because those pictures are still out there, obviously, like floating around. And so people will be like, oh, well, she has a horrible boob job. And I want to be like, I've got them redone. They don't look like that anymore.
What do you have, D's right now? Are they D's?
They're 32 double D.
Wow. What'd you have originally, like low C?
I had like B, C. They were just really nice. They were perfect. In hindsight, I probably, if I knew then what I know now, I wouldn't have done it. But, I mean, I'm happy with the way they are now, but, you know, you always have bad boob job pictures out there when you get a bad boob job.
And so, you obviously like yours.
Oh, I love hers mine. Oh, my gosh. I will never get mine redone because I'm afraid that they're going to mess them up.
Yeah,
my doctor's retired, so I don't have my doctor
anymore.
So that's
it. You just got to go with those.
Yeah.
No,
and I'm totally happy.
Now, what about, like, after, you know, so you get into it, you do that, was it easy to start getting a little more hardcore? What do you do? Like, anything?
Started out hardcore.
DP and shit like that?
No.
No? What kind of hardcore stuff you do?
I don't do, okay, well, that hardcore that you're talking about, I don't do hardcore, like, I don't do anal.
No.
I only do straight up boy-girl scenes with, like, 5 guys that I know.
5 guys, not at the same time?
No.
No.
That would be fun, but, you know, I can't be put out like that.
Yeah. So like
there's a line
you're
that
talking,
every girl draws.
You're talking, the scene starts, clothes come off, you start sucking his dick, he goes down on you, some straight fucking, pulls it out, in your mouth, comes on your face.
Yeah.
Oh, that's perfect. How it goes.
You are ornery, Anthony.
Scene.
And scene.
That's the routine.
What? You are ornery.
No, I was just describing.
Just like, he's the blunt to the point guy. I love it.
Yeah.
Opie's over there acting completely unexcited about the entire thing.
No, because that's cool. I like that because you can fast forward
don't make me
to your favorite shit without having
that's
to guess.
Really
like, it's like, what's coming up? All right, I want to see a cum shot on a face. I want to see him fucking. I want, you know, the back of the ball shot.
Like that.
You know, you got that camera down there.
Here's a little action shot.
There you go. Holy mother of.
Oh, whoa.
Do you remember that dick?
That's a nice action shot.
Yeah.
That was a good one. I came really hard on that thing.
Wow.
Yeah, you're making
What video are we looking at for the people out there?
Where she's looking over her shoulder like, fuck me good.
This is a scene from babygotboobs.com. It's part of browsers.
Nice.
Baby got boobs. And this, I'm actually having sex with this guy who was like my mom's boyfriend because she wouldn't let me go out with my boyfriend. So it's like payback's a bitch.
So he comes over and, hi, how are you?
Whoa. I totally seduced him.
Your
yeah.
mom's not home.
No,
what are
I
you doing here?
Him.
Hey, what are you doing to me? One of those things.
I seduced him.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what I mean. It's like you go over and you start going like, hi, and he's like, what? But I'm your mom's boyfriend.
Yeah, pretty much. I like pretty much
awkward
dragged
until his
him into the
fat
room.
Schlong comes out.
Did you write the script for this movie?
Oh, believe me. I've seen so many. I love them.
I've written porn
scripts. Wow. That's a fat dick.
Yeah.
Come on. He's fucking on the diet. Wait. Eric, I'm sorry you had to hear that.
Can we get that one off? Thanks.
Yeah, yeah.
Wait, you don't like that one?
No, I just don't want that all put out and stuff.
Who is the guy?
I don't know.
Wow. Well, you don't like that one, huh?
No, can you please change that?
Why don't
you
like it's
that
not, picture? Because it's not a flattering picture.
It's
of course
not.
It is.
A mouth that doesn't look like
what
she's...
better photo of person?
You need to put up this picture. Look how pretty.
Yeah, that is.
This is a good picture right here.
Yeah. Yeah, don't worry about that shit.
That's right.
Nothing.
You guys are so bad.
Yeah, I know. You guys are really mean.
No.
Actually.
Am I being mean?
Yeah.
Anthony, you're being great.
Fuck, what did I do? Really? Serious. I want to be serious for a second. What did I do that was mean? Because I was just like interviewing you in the way I would interview somebody that does adult films.
I realize that.
All right, I apologize.
Do you feel Anthony was too harsh in his descriptions?
I just would rather be seen as a penthouse pet today and not an adult film hardcore sex addict.
Oh my god, don't get upset with me. I can't take it. I got
Anthony
too many.
I
got too many fucking girls upset with me today. Enough of this shit.
Why are people upset with you?
Because I must be a fucking asshole.
There's enough big juicy cock for all.
Yeah. Yeah, it's true.
Anthony loves you, by the way.
I swear to God. I think you're stunning.
He adores you.
I think you're stunningly attractive.
Well, I'm here promoting my Penthouse magazine for March 2009. Everybody check it out. Thank you.
Shit, did I fuck this up?
No, you didn't. It's all salvageable.
No. Look at her face.
I think if you go over there and give her a foot massage, she'll forgive you.
Wait, she's pissed, Anthony.
Go give her a foot massage and she'll forgive you.
My feet totally don't hurt anymore.
Mad.
I'll give you a foot massage.
She's here to promote Penthouse.
She is.
Yeah.
She's on stands right now. So we're here trying to get everybody to buy this issue and come see us.
See, I was just trying to make a conversation.
In Paramus, New Jersey,
so
we can sign everything.
But we remember before.
Everything was fine before.
It was fine before.
Can we go back, when it was all fine?
Yes, we can.
I didn't screw it up.
I've been getting pissed off for like 20 minutes now.
Are you shitting me?
No kidding.
What part got you?
Like, you guys make me feel like a little girl, and you keep calling me cute. And then you make me feel, like, so dirty. Like, you make me feel gross and young and a little girl.
What are we supposed to do?
That is unnecessary.
It really
is. That is really unnecessary.
We don't know.
Look, my hands aren't on the computer.
Yeah, well, who's
at all. That would be Danny.
Danny pops him up there.
Yeah. I have to say, I think you're being a little sensitive about
it. Wait, Danny, what's up?
Well, I mean, I don't...
Jimmy!
I'm not here promoting cum on my face right now. I'm here promoting...
Well, it looks like you just were licking like...
This is
stuff that you've done in your career, right?
And what I'm promoting today.
I understand, but it's something that you've did. It's in your past.
What I'm promoting. This is not from Penthouse.
All right, but if we had De Niro in studio, we'd be talking about Raging Bull and Dog Day After...
Penthouse?
Can I be honest? I think one reason, though, you got to say this... Is the video that was on the console for me when I got here?
Yeah,
a Penthouse. It's called "Bring Me the Head of Shauna Linne." So it is a Penthouse video.
Yes,
she's promoting Penthouse.
That.
So but that, you, she's saying that's
that
not
is
penthouse.
Not Penthouse. No,
the radio audience. The radio audience cannot see that. All they hear is our descriptions.
Well, I hope not.
How could the radio audience see
it? No, they don't see it.
So what they hear is us describing scenes which are sexy of you, which makes people want to go out and buy
I didn't know she was getting mad for 20 minutes.
Three, two.
I thought I was doing very well with you.
Wow.
Scene from Arthur. Yeah. Funny.
Yeah, Anthony was
Let's
really
talk about Rock and Love Bus.
I thought it was
Can we talk about what we're supposed to be talking about?
You're even starting to annoy me, and I'm
very
easy.
Hey, Jimmy.
I gotta be honest. Now, I'm very tolerant, but the Penthouse video, we're promoting Penthouse as a brand.
Yeah.
Talking about hardcore stuff, saying the pictures are very sexy.
And, you know,
come on.
You
guys were not putting sexy pictures up there.
They are.
You guys were picking out the worst pictures you guys could find and putting them up there.
No, it's kind of hot. I swear. I swear.
He was putting up just dirty pictures, which we
did. They're very sexy. They're very sexy and very hot.
There was one that was really sexy when you were getting it from behind.
No, they are. They're very sexy.
Looking back and stuff.
Hey, stop it.
It was nice.
I was saying, they're very sexy.
Yeah.
You're a very pretty girl, and I didn't mean to, you know.
Those pictures were not. So you guys picked out, like, seriously, like, oh, awesome, thanks. I'm
stop,
out.
Don't, no.
Oh, what's wrong with that,
God, a, I knew it. I fucking knew
what's
it.
What's wrong? It's a picture.
Why are you guys doing this?
To be honest, I gotta say, that
it's
what
just
is
her
wrong?
Sucking on a big black.
Hey, you guys, come on.
No,
be
no,
nice.
No.
What? I got, how are we supposed to know this is nothing put wrong with the that? Edge?
It's a
I'm
dirty
there's
photo.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with
it's
it.
It's just
she's,
her sucking
know?
On the big ball bag of the black gentleman.
Exactly.
What's wrong with it? Where did Anthony go?
I can't.
Why?
Aunt,
I can't deal with this situation
what?
Now. I feel so bad.
I don't.
Paul,
I never
don't
fuck with the girls that come in here. Never. Never.
Oh, Paul, do
Paul's
I feel
got a,
terrible.
Yeah, I'll got talk a wireless
to
her. Mic.
She's here to promote. Well, you know something. She's here to promote Penthouse.
She looks beautiful
on the cover.
Wait.
I'm trying to promote my penthouse issue, and that's not what I fucking came here for. I'm sorry. Honey, it's okay. No, fuck these people. They're assholes.
Oh,
yeah. Really
get
them
back in
they're
here.
They're fucking assholes.
Aww.
I've never been treated like this on the radio.
Oh.
You wrote Howard's fucking whatever the fuck he calls that insertion machine. Shut up.
Opie,
come on.
Opie, be nice, or I'm gonna have to leave too. Because if everybody leaves,
look,
I have to leave.
I know.
We didn't have
Opie.
That wasn't our intention, trust me. Anne was being very cool and like getting to know and stuff, and actually, if I dare say, I see a little twinkle in Anthony's eye when he first saw her, so he was definitely trying to be even nicer than he would in general.
If you listen to any interview with any girl that's done any adult films from me, it will be the same question.
Well, I think what she's saying is, you know, she's very proud of, you know, she just was announced as the pet of the year runner-up, and I think that she's...
Yes.
Hey, oh, no. Who's got the mic? Ask her if the
problem... You know what? I'm getting fucking... Tell her to fucking leave though. She's not happy. No. This is really Jimmy. Beginning to fucking
ask her. Jimmy. Ask her if she's just ashamed of what she's done in her life.
No. Oh, God. Oh, no.
What's going
you
on,
you guys
Danny?
Are putting me in the middle of a very awkward situation.
I know. You're really
her
in an awkward situation.
First scene was shot with a fucking good friend of mine. I don't want to fucking hear this shit. Silver's a good buddy of mine.
But I'm saying if everybody gets upset,
no one is shitting on
her
stuff.
No
one is shitting on
her.
Sam, where is she?
She's in the office.
All right, let's listen in. Can we get the mic better?
Yeah, we are.
You guys, I don't want to leave.
I know.
We'll always love you. Don't worry about it. You come back whenever you want.
I know, but I'm saying I don't want to leave just because, you know, the situation went bad.
How are we supposed to know?
Make her stay.
I can't make her do anything.
She can't make you leave.
Sam, what's up? Steve, what's up? What's up, B-Rock?
I hate being an asshole.
Boo-hoo!
Boo-hoo! Boo-hoo!
Oh, Jesus.
Shut up.
Oh,
we were being nice.
Oh, there's a mic. Oh, no.
Okay. Whatever. We were being nice. Shut up.
No, they were like, they were just making a fun of the fact that I'm young and cute and talking about old. We're almost abducted, and I'm trying
you're
to
almost abducted.
I was trying to make a joke out of it. And I was trying to make a joke out
holy
of it.
Shit, this one's got issues.
No, it's not. I was making a joke about it. They were like, you can't walk down the street unless you're like, or you'll get abducted.
I see.
I'm serious, trying to aware people, and it's like everything I said came back and kicked me a fucking ass.
I know. But this is how we learn.
Cute ass, too.
No,
yeah.
Lucky foot. Just saying.
She's adorable. There, like,
she's that. This is exactly the girls I wind up with, too. We're destined for each other.
Dude, I want to say
me
that.
Me and her are destined for each other.
I was going to say that, but I thought
a cute, young-looking girl who's crazy as a shithouse rat. Those are the fucking girls I end up with. We're going
to... Who?
Derek.
Turn up the fucking volume!
You're going to be my wife, Lorraine!
ever want to go on radio again.
Back to the Future.
Honey, that's not reference. How it was, and the other Lady, shows that I, we're going to go on.
Serious?
Honey, stop.
I will not have set myself up for this again. I will not.
When you were in New York before...
She has no idea what we've done with broads on this show over the years.
I think we should talk about something else.
Yeah, what's entertaining? I want
to
hear this.
It's Obama.
Toomey's like, no. Obama's trying to instill a stimulus package. And it's going to put the world...
Hey, we'll get back to your ego in a second. Hold on a minute.
My ego. I just want to redirect
it. No, let her take it. She's fucking... She's being an asshole.
Show.
Yeah, I don't trust any other...
Honey, you can't be that way just because of one experience, okay? Just this show.
I will never set my... You gotta understand, I don't want to be set up for another experience.
And
like, even if I go on another show, they might do the same exact fucking thing.
But honey, not every show is gonna... The rest of the day, the shows that we're doing are not gonna be like this. They're the shows that you've done already. Okay?
I don't trust anybody right now.
What a fucking baby.
Honey.
I really don't know. I don't trust anybody.
Alright, first of all, forget about us. You gotta
call. I'm calm. I'm just saying.
She's
I'm
unstable,
done.
Man.
That's it.
You gotta have a thicker skin. I know.
I've heard rumors, too, about
really?
Don't
make me take out the
Here's my thick skin. I will not go through this experience again. That is my thick skin, lady. I know I'm crying, and... You think I don't have things, but I do have a perspective on what's going on in my life right now. And what's going on in my life right now is that I never want to do radio again because I do not want to be set up for this.
Can I ask you something? This is not even about this. Is there something going on with you? Because you seem that you get upset. Like, is there something going on in your personal life or something? Or is this just your nature? Because
I guess it's just me.
On almost every trip, you break down at one point and stuff. And I'm like, is something bothering you?
I get homesick. I want to go home. Like, I don't like being away from home.
You told me you wanted to come here.
But, you know, I thought every time I go somewhere, I think I can do it. And apparently I'm not good at what I am.
You are. You're great, but you don't know.
This shit's just making me sad now.
No kidding. She turned me
into a shit. I did not roll with this shit.
What do you think? Some other girls don't get shit sometimes?
Well, they can go through it. I'm not. Yeah, but I don't want to go. I'm not going to set myself up to go through
shit. And you walked off. And you walked off. And that's fine. I've had girls walk off shows. It's okay. All right.
She would write her a check in.
She wants to be home.
It'll make her feel good.
She hates being away from home.
It's so fine. Yeah. Whatever. It's done. I don't give a fuck about any person in this building.
All right,
it's
now fine. I'm mad at you.
Yeah, bitch.
I'm talking about moving forward. Not today. Moving forward. I do not want to go on a radio because I do not want to.
Man, I don't know how Ronnie's going to do a show with Fez acting like this today.
Oh, God. That's a good one.
I
feel sorry for Ronnie.
You know, do you not think that a lot of girls have to go through this? I mean, it's part of the business.
No, I don't want to go through it, so I'm done. I've been thinking about getting out for a while,
so
whatever.
So, you know, maybe you should. Maybe you should after this tour. I'm serious. Maybe you should take a break. I'm talking to you as a friend, not as your publicist. I think you should
I'm not even taking a break. I'm fucking done with everybody.
Everything I say,
very
upset.
I am upset because everything I said came back and kicked me the fucking.
Honey, it's just. You think they had to give Tay a hard time on
the
show?
We found the worst picture ever. To really
holy.
I thought that was just sexy. Like, why would she be bothered by that?
First one was hot. Second one, where they're shoving as much cock into her mouth as possible, was a little rough.
What was wrong with that?
Well, she apparently is trying to redirect herself.
She's still making a more.
Getting upset and they just keep picking like that's the fuck up thing. Where when I say that, hey, can you take that down?
So you know
you gotta understand. I asked them to take it off. Sure, they put a worse one up.
Yeah, and then a worse one went up.
That's all. You walked off and that's it. Fuck them, alright?
Who is she talking
to? We're done.
Lainey, who's very good. Cool. Lainey's great.
Okay, she brings us all these girls.
I don't want this ruining your trip.
Yeah.
You're having a good time otherwise.
A good time all the
time.
Someone's just going to be coddled like that. It's like, how about this? Shut your face.
What do you think you do for a living?
It's okay. No one was knocking it. It was sexy. Nobody was demeaning you.
No.
Here's the thing. There are people waiting for you at the signing.
Oh, she doesn't want to go to the signing.
Oh, brother.
Boy, have fun at the signing. She's a real charmer.
Oh.
you can meet Taya and the head case at the Romantic Depot. What's more romantic than this?
It's in Paramus from noon to two. So go. Tears are optional.
I don't think you do.
What am I supposed to tell all these people?
I don't care. I don't know.
What am I?
Well, you tell them. Tell them she's going through menopause 40 years early.
People are coming to see you.
Holy
shit. People, the store,
how confused can one person be? She's on the front page of...
Why you don't punish people who didn't do anything wrong to you? It's not fair.
Fucking this no, shots
were... That's what you're
saying. I don't know. It's fucking irritating, dude.
You don't want to do the radio the rest of the day? That's fine, but you need to do the science.
Hey, yeah, when she comes out, everybody should boo.
Oh, shit. Oh, come on, Sparrow's going to lose her mind.
Just an autograph.
Not very stable.
Well, you know what, though? She's being unreasonable.
I'm just playing the good guy. Don't worry about this. I'm just as big a scumbag as all of you.
She's being unreasonable. Like, I don't like to fuck with the girls if they're really cool. Like, I never do. But she's being unreasonable.
Yeah.
After the signing, you don't have to do the rest of the day's radio, all right?
No, it's like, this is real stuff. It's like, how have I been? I was...
She's being unreasonable. So is, So is what's his name? Cheswick.
That's exactly who we're dealing with. I don't want your nipples or your nipples. I want my nipples.
I haven't been working in this business for 15, 18 years. I haven't seen everyone.
Should we have a whole crowd start a chant?
I know I'm not new, but
oh my God, no.
No, I like the fact, I like Lainey.
I'm sorry.
I like hearing this negotiation. I like this negotiation.
Unfortunately, not everything is good. Because you're mean asshole.
Oh, shit. Dan, by the way, behind the scenes, Danny is one of the most notoriously biggest pricks. He's just got shit. He wants to unload howitzers.
You don't have, I'm compromising and working with you.
Yeah.
You don't have to do the radio for the rest of the week.
Yeah.
Okay? Rest of the week. I have all these shows planned.
Just come over. She can, relax.
She doesn't want to do fucking promotion. What a fucking baby.
I'm trying to be patient with you, too. I'm trying to be nice to you and explain to you what's going on.
This issue's
going to
sell.
Big time.
Yeah, yeah. Who doesn't want to see this?
Yeah, there's like a good emotional breakdown.
The girl's ridiculous looking, by the way.
I'm done for the whole entire day. Like, I'm not going to go into an autograph site and be smiley and sign pictures.
Please tell her. Please tell her how. No, if you go to the autograph signing, please just say how cute she is.
Yeah, just tell her she's cute.
You're cute. What a cutie patootie. Use Rosie's.
I'm so embarrassed.
Cutiekins, cutie pie.
Never seen one of these girls whose skin is thinner than the pages her nude pictures are on.
Jesus Christ, I know. Should we have David go in there and try to spook this?
Opie, radio genius. Get David.
David.
With a microphone.
David has to smooth things over.
With his headset.
Just tell him to smooth things over.
David, I want you to go in there and go, the guys really want you to come back on the show.
Go talk to her. Smooth things over.
Smooth things over. Don't just go right with the question.
Get him a fucking headset right now.
Don't just go right with the question.
Smooth things over
first.
Just
break into the conversation.
Say, you know... Agree with her.
David.
Yeah, that might not hurt. That he,
I got it.
Oh, yeah, David.
Go in, break up the conversation and go, the guys want to know when the whore is coming back into the studio.
It's part of the joke, David.
It's part of the joke, David. Yes.
You know what, David?
It might give you an executive intern.
Okay, don't say whore. Just say, look. Okay, no, just say when the cute girl is coming back in the studio.
You gotta say when you're coming back.
They want to know when the cute girl is coming back in. What the fuck's wrong with that? Go.
Go ahead, David. Break into the conversation.
David, go.
Does he got a microphone?
He doesn't need one.
There's one in the office.
Derek, turn that up a little.
All right, here we go.
I can't.
David's going
to
break
it. I wouldn't be able to do it if I'm not so fucking embarrassed out of my mind. It'd be no problem.
Honey, you have no reason to be embarrassed.
Yeah.
What did you do? You didn't make a fool out of yourself. You didn't do anything wrong. You didn't do anything wrong.
Yeah, right.
Wrong.
It's
what? What? You're not
really
listening.
Really not what
they
said.
So what do you give a shit, honey? You can't. What do you care about what everyone's
saying?
Because
they're ruining my image on the fucking radio.
Oh, no. No one listens to this show. Don't worry about it.
Fucking position for people to use me.
Yeah.
No. They
want to
know when she's going to come back into that room. And, like,
they
want to know. They really upset that what they did to her. They apologized.
I don't care.
She's really, I'm not kidding.
I'm done.
I'm
not ever going on the radio again.
I know she's upset, but so are the guys. Like, Anthony's really upset. You didn't mean to say
that.
All right.
What happened?
I told them I was upset and they just kept fucking
just not to like talk or anything. Oh, they're just really sorry. They like to apologize on the air. They're sorry.
Did you hear what they said, honey?
I hear it from you.
you take this mic?
I'll tell you, way to go, man. Way to bring us a head case today. Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Stop that.
I blame you.
They pushed me out.
I blame you.
No, you can't. You blame me for everything.
You can talk character.
All right, well, that's just wonderful.
Maybe I can help.
Well, we're going to be at the Romantic Depot in Paramus, New Jersey from noon to 2.
Oh.
So come see us, and I will sign things and give you hugs.
Aw. What's the matter, Ira?
All right.
Look, our people are waiting for something to happen.
Well, they trust me, they're here for a classic. They're not stupid.
But you guys are still having fun, right?
Yeah!
Yeah. Get naked, will you?
I'm like bummed out now. I don't even...
Here's someone that knows who she is. Now go get naked for these guys.
Oh, God.
Opie, Anthony, I don't know. This is...
I didn't say anything.
You want to talk to Shauna?
I was being really nice.
Anthony, do you want to go talk to her?
Should I?
Go give her a hug or something. Go say you're sorry and give her a hug.
She'd be okay with that?
She'd maybe.
Yell
at me.
Well, grab the mic so she knows she's on the air.
Say you're sorry and give her a hug.
Grab the mic so she knows she's on the air. Take the mic there. Ant's good at this stuff.
I don't like the headphones. That's too much. I don't need this.
Oh, this is ugly.
Hi. Hi.
Jim, your face.
Okay, no. Okay.
All right, no mic. Just one.
Is this on?
Yeah.
Anthony's talking to her.
Okay.
There's no Michael Ad in the room.
Okay.
But he's trying to smooth things over.
Right. Some of her conversation was being picked up by the audience, Mike. What's going on, Sam?
She gave him the dismissive thumbs up, and is just nodding him off and saying, I know. Let me see what I can do here.
Oh, Ant's back. Wow, I've never seen you look like this before.
What happened?
Did you just see a psychopath?
That didn't go well.
What happened? What happened?
Well, I punched her. No, I just kind of explained, you know, the situation.
Yeah.
Were you sensitive, Anthony? Hi. I love when Anthony like gets sensitive. He's like, we were just trying to.
I was just trying to smooth things over, you know. But there's not much smoothing.
Really?
Going to be done.
I don't want to smooth it over. What'd she say to you?
Nothing. It was mostly hand signals.
Really?
Yeah.
God, you were being
different.
I
fingers.
I swear to everyone out there, it was being so nice. He actually. He was actually really, attracted to her.
She's a pretty girl. Of course, you'd have to be nuts not to think, you know.
No, but I mean,
she
it was a little more than that.
Fucking
like,
annoyed
oh,
me so much.
But Jimmy, you get annoyed at girls like that because you're so used to, you know, having to pay them.
The girls that come in, especially the penthouse girls, and I'm not even just saying that because you're penthouse. The penthouse girls are universally fucking great. Like, there's been no... Yeah. They're all fucking cool.
Uh-huh.
That's the first one I can think of, whether it was Justine Jolie or fucking Victoria Zdrock or fucking Brie Olsen or yourself. They're all cool.
Thank you.
Yeah.
But her, she's the first one that was like, what, take my shirt? Why? I didn't want to press my tits up. What? Like, what are we doing? You don't know how to have fun on a radio show?
You're completely naked.
What do you think you're going to do? Just talk about the cover?
Magazines.
Well, here's a magazine, and that's going to entertain fucking a million-something people listening. It doesn't make sense.
Well, maybe she's, you know... not as comfortable with what she has to do or is doing as the other girls.
How about this? It's a fiercely competitive business. You want to fucking sell magazines? You got to promote. How do you think you're getting people to buy fucking paper magazines in a computer internet world? You got to go on the radio and talk about it and make people like you and want to see you. What do you think? That you're going to say, hi, I'm on the cover, and anybody's going to give a shit?
But I think that was part of the problem is, you know, she wanted to promote the paper thing, and there was the old internet.
Yeah, but you know what?
Oh, Jesus.
I was also talking...
Oh, God damn you, Danny.
She wouldn't like this one. Wow.
We were talking about the fucking... she did a penthouse video. That's all part of penthouse. What's the fucking problem?
Shut up. I'm watching the video.
Oh, sorry. Yeah.
All right, why don't we get in then? Lainey's got to get her out of here because.
Yeah. She gotta, you know. Oh, boy.
Lainey's very good.
We like Lainey a lot.
Very much.
She does a lot for this radio show. She knows how to find him, that's for sure. Oh, a little slap.
Oh, boy. Wow.
Now she won't even go to the sign.
It's accommodating.
Why is she doing this then?
Well.
Well, I think. Like I was talking
about. I'm not even talking about the porn because she might have moved on from this. Who knows? But why is she even in a magazine naked if she's like this sensitive about everything?
Well, I don't. I think, honestly, I think she's just like I was telling Anthony, I think she's, you know, she's going and doing these radio shows right now promoting her issue and the fact that she just, you know, won Pet of the Year runner up. And so I think that maybe she just. I mean, I don't know. I haven't really talked to her about this. I'm kind of just an observer myself. But I think that maybe she just thought it was going to be more talking about, you know, what she's I don't know. I'm just trying to help.
Let me play devil's advocate.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
All right.
Never.
You have lifts. You ought to stand on your medication. Let me ask. Okay, here's how we do it. You're on the cover penthouse, right?
Yes, sir.
Let's talk about that. No, for real. Not Rock of Love, not any of it. Let's talk about the magazine.
About what about it? What do you want to know about it?
Okay, I don't know.
I was already here promoting my. I mean, I'm.
Give me
here.
A fucking answer!
I don't know what to say! I'm trying to salvage this.
No,
situation.
But I'm saying even her magazine. Let's promote her magazine. This is. I'm only saying this because.
No, I totally agree with what you're saying. I totally get what you're saying. I just think that maybe she got upset because.
I plugged her
fuck
fucking.
Sake, man, you're amateur.
I plugged the listener. I plugged the signing.
No, you asked Jim. You know
we,
I love
we,
you.
We plugged the fucking. I plugged your video because it says penthouse on it, and we plugged the magazine and said she was smoking in it. It's like
you're right. You're right.
What the fuck do you want? But what do you want from a radio show?
No,
you don't
right.
just walk on and go, "Hi, I'm hot," and fucking people give a fuck in their cars. Nobody cares.
We were being really being nice.
That's
you
what
guys
bugged
were being
her.
Nice. You guys,
we liked
Opie
her a
was
lot.
Mean to me last time, and I still stayed.
Holy mackerel!
Maybe she's mad because she's never recovered from that.
Oh. she's coming out.
Okay, she's coming out.
All right. Get them off the screen.
Why?
Don't ruin everything.
Fucker.
Right. Yeah, put on the audience monitor. Danny, put on the audience monitor.
Supposedly she rode Howard's fuck machine yesterday, too. It's like, hello, shut up.
Oh, really? Really? Don't you?
That's what I'm hearing a ton of.
The Symbian
thanks for listening to us
Sabian
instead of Howard, by the
called.
Way, you asses that gave me the info.
And
everybody boo.
No.
Boo-hoo! Oh, boo-hoo!
Bye. I hope everything works out okay. If you need a Little Mermaid room to stay in, I know where there is one.
I'm giving away your room.
Oh, man.
Where's she now?
Holy fuck!
To Maisie, that doesn't make her cry. There's a giant penis in her hiney. It looks like the fucking Titanic going into the Lincoln.
Speaking of Lincoln.
I know. Wow. That video makes you realize the mistake.
She was making out with some broad on Howard's show yesterday.
Screw.
Oh, was she really?
What's up, Steve?
You weren't there? I was going to ask, was she upset after yesterday's show? That she did with
Star.
Lainey was very apologetic, first of all, because Lainey has. We have extensive conversations before the girls ever come on. They know exactly what they're walking into. And
they do. She actually gives us like a breakdown of every show we're going to do and what is to be expected on the show. And it says,
No, I know. And Taya's last appearance was fucking huge. It's all over the goddamn internet now. And it went perfectly. And Lainey's baffled by this, and she's very apologetic because she wasn't expecting this because her appearance.
Who they could've? Do. She said, I think it actually says, I actually have my paper in there that breaks down like what the show is. And said, it's a man, it's a dude that show. It's guys being guys. And they're going to kind of be raunchy. And so we definitely know everything we're walking into every time we go on to every show because Lainey is very thorough about that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Opie's having an episode.
Look, for somebody who wanted to be a porn actress since she was 12, and that's 8 years ago, and then she's been doing it. And then she's been doing it. I don't buy the fucking self-centered horseshit routine. And I'm very rarely annoyed at the girls that come in. That was fucking nonsense, and it was irritating.
She's all she's thought about irritating. In her life is cock, like, so God forbid we talk about it a little
because
bit.
I don't like that fucking bullshit.
I know, but you're so sweet and so nice. I like Jimmy.
So when somebody is being a fucking phony or a head case, they got to be called out.
Is she out of the building?
Yeah, she's downstairs having a smoke.
Oh, good. Okay.
She should think about cancer.
No, I don't know. Okay. No, I don't have to deal with it.
I think she's jonesing or something because there's yesterday on Howard Show her riding the fucking
big smile on her face. You know, where are the fucking tears?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, we should have showed her that. Yeah, exactly. How is that promoting the fucking spread being on a mechanical bull?
Yeah.
Tay, is it true she wants?
I honestly just met her a couple weeks ago. I don't have any idea.
Pass that buck. I like that.
Atta girl.
She's running away crying those crocodile tears. Now that she's gone, I'll make a goof. I thought I had a shot.
I know.
I think that's funny, too.
I saw it in your eye.
And you got red. When you're joke bombed, Anthony actually got a little red. And Anthony never gives a shit. None of us care if our joke's bombed.
No.
But, you know what it was? When somebody said shot, you did like a shot a load joke?
Yes.
Yeah. And that might have been
I was like, oh, yeah, the shot a load joke. And then I kind of spelt out how the movies work. Where it's, you know, that, and then the blowjob, and then the fucking, and the cum in the face. And it was like, you know, I could see then she was just kind of like, eh. Once I saw the eyes welling up, I just stepped back and left it to the fucking two destroyers to move in for the kill.
I usually don't do that.
I'm the picador.
Hold on.
I go in there and just stick a few swords in. You guys are the matadors.
I got to slightly defend myself.
Oh, what?
I was rated destroyer, and Jimmy and I both felt at the same time when she goes, I'm homesick. Then I was done. I'm like, all right, you know, let's leave her alone. And then she went right back to trash us. I'm like, you know, fuck it.
Then I got annoyed when I found out that she was on Howard's show doing stuff.
She's homesick.
It's terrible, isn't it? It's terrible.
Sorry.
Tragic. If you're on one show doing stuff, and then we're actually not
open the
being
window
dicks.
So we could yell at her on the street.
Oh my God!
You guys,
and then we could throw some mustard on her too.
I want to lay her down and put a door with rocks on it on her, like in Crowhaven Farm. I knew it. Nobody saw that movie but me. I want to punish the heretic.
Well,
I know, went over everybody's head, including the people who are in Crowhaven Farm. It scared me when I was a boy. I made wee-wee in my tough skins.
I want to thank Taya for wrecking the show today. So,
because
we were going to have to leave now.
Opie,
Taya was very nice today. Go see Taya. Go to the sign and just
Taya
support
rules,
Taya
actually.
Parker.
You'll love her.
She's fucking really, she's great, and she's on Rock of Love Bus.
I mean, the other one's hotter, but Taya rules, so you should,
Honestly, I don't think so. I think Taya, I'm much more attracted to Taya.
Oh, thank you, honey.
I mean, she's a pretty girl, but...
Not Taya, you're yes.
You
that's
fucking,
okay, Opie, I'm not for everybody.
That's why you beat her. Hands down, you humiliated her in the fucking penthouse of the year thing. They only gave her a second to be polite. She actually came in 11th in the voting. I know, the Guccione's faxed me.
Oh, wow.
You should have,
Well, you can come see me at the Romantic Depot, noon to 2.
Is that a porn
Paramus,
place?
New Jersey. Yeah, it's like a...
It's Paramus, like a by the way. Don't say Paramus. Yeah.
Paramus.
Anymore, this is not Manhattan.
I'm sorry.
That's
I don't
just,
know.
It's your
full
like it today,
now.
Though.
Manhattan. Damn, Manhattan.
So what are you, what are you doing after this?
I'm actually on VH1 on Brett Michaels' show, The Rock of Love.
Oh,
and
Jesus.
Every Sunday at 9 o'clock. And you guys can go to my website,
TayaParker.com.
TayaParker.com.
Hey, that's wonderful.
And what about, what's her name there?
Shauna Linnae.
Shauna
Linnae.
What is Psychopath?
Is that BootyHootyHoo.com?
Hey, come on, sports fans. I want to bounce a basketball over her head like
you're
a great
gonna
Santini.
Squirt? You're going
to
squirt?
Have you guys been watching Rock of Love Bus? You guys had Brett on here, right?
Yes.
Mm. What, did you say anything nice about me?
He did. He actually raved about you. I have not been watching it because I had a fucking problem with my stupid DVR. Steve has seen every episode. Tell her what you were saying about the one episode you did. Just fucking say it.
Opie, I can hear you. I have headphones on.
Hold on, Taya. What was the one episode that bugged you? Guy, tell her.
Steve loves this show.
Oh, I do. I love that show, but I have privileged information and I can't.
What? Shame.
You know, I can't.
Just tell her what you like, what you were watching that you enjoyed. Come on, there was one part he fucking wouldn't stop talking about. Tell her.
It was the part where the girls got really drunk and made out with each other, and it was just very impressive.
Whoa!
Which time?
Which time?
Well, you know, that's the part I was talking about.
What?
Yeah.
No, tell her which time, though. I wasn't
drunk making out with any girls.
No,
wait, talking about me.
No, no, but wait till the time. The one with the thing with you that, that you said.
Right.
Tell, come on.
Right.
Just fucking say
what,
it.
What, with a dog?
What?
Oven
like the part with the dog? What are you talking about?
Why are you
go
shy
ahead.
Now? Tell us.
Don't be shy.
I know, he's afraid to be a man.
It's on TV, everyone has seen it.
I know, that's what I'm trying to tell him.
I have no pride anymore. Go ahead,
tell
what
her.
Is it?
Tell her.
It's the part with the, you know.
What?
You know, the oven mitts and the dog.
The parts with the oven mitts and the
what?
Dog. What are you
what?
Talking about?
We'll what?
Cut this out of the replay, Daddy.
What are you talking about?
It's just an improv thing.
Yeah, I know. They're trying to...
No, but I tell
he's
her...
He's trying to get me to admit to something. Like,
no,
what,
no,
did
no,
you
no
see
I'm
that?
Not. No. Steve's just being shy. Because I'm like, you got to tell her that thing you were telling us. He's like, well, she'll get really mad at me.
I want... Listen, I don't get mad. If it's on TV, listen, my life is an open book. You can ask me about anything you want. And I will be honest.
Of course.
Go ahead.
Have you ever taken it in the shitter?
I have not.
Okay. I think you told us that last time. Were you
I
the one
not.
That fell off the stage?
I am the one that
say
fell
I
off the stage.
I watched the show.
I am.
She was doing a roadie thing. She
and
fell
it was
off the
hysterical.
Stage. She was crying a little bit, but you know what? She was a trooper, and then she got back up there and started doing more of that roadie.
No, I started crying after I fell, because I really noticed. I actually fell off a 6-foot stage
I know,
on my back.
But then you went back
you're
to
all
work.
A bunch of crybabies.
No, I wasn't actually.
Like
I
me
right
when spaghetti hits the wall.
Working. I think I did a really good job, actually.
Yeah.
Steve, what was the thing you were going to ask me? Don't try to skirt out of here.
I'm not skirting out of here.
Come on. Cough it up.
Cough it up. It'll be
cough
white,
it
viscous, and salty. Are you implying that I'm homosexual?
Yes. No, so you got to tell her, man. Just tell her.
Just tell me. I'm not.
She's fine, Steve.
Sort of
I told you she's very cool.
It seems like you're
Steve
very...
thinks you're really uptight for some reason. I'm like, there's no way she's uptight.
What?
I'm not... Believe me, I know you're not.
Well,
I might,
you know,
I might play uptight on TV.
I don't know, it just seems like the other girls just, you know, have kind of a toot about you, you know, they just, they don't like you a whole lot.
That's okay. I didn't go on there expecting to be liked.
Yeah,
especially
you know
when
that.
You go on a
her,
show
man?
Trying to date
well,
a
no,
rock star.
Well, no, because that's, you know, like, it just seems like the other girls are kind of bitchy about you. You know,
they
kind
are,
of,
and they should be.
And why?
I mean, probably just because, I mean, I went into a show to date a rock star, and last time I checked my record books, like, rock stars and centerfolds work out pretty well. So I think they thought,
oh,
hey, she
sure
might,
do.
You know, have trumped me already
better than radio
in the beginning.
Stars
so,
false,
you know what I mean? I didn't expect to make friends. I honestly
shot,
didn't.
Though,
I expected there to be a lot of hating going on.
Yeah.
So, you know, they directed it at me, and that was fine.
So
I mean, I was
that,
okay.
See, I told you she wouldn't care. So tell her the incident. Tell her
go
the
ahead. Go ahead.
Go ahead. You were fucking raving about it. You said that you thought she was a little fucked up.
There's nothing on your BlackBerry.
He thought you were wrong.
Goddamn BlackBerry.
So I'm like, that's...
No, tell me.
Tell her.
And you know what? I might have an explanation. It might have been an editing situation. Trust
yes,
me, I've watched it, and there's a lot of effed up editing going
yeah,
on.
Yeah, I know. Really? That's why I try to tell him. He's like, no, she's fucked up. I'm like,
no, I'm really not. Go ahead.
Well, but, you know, like it had to do with a lot of booze, you know?
Exactly. Boo.
Yeah. I knew that was coming.
What is he talking
boo.
About?
Steve, please. Come on. You got to go
you can't
next.
Just,
you
like,
can't.
In, you know, infer, because then people that are listening are like, what's going on? Maybe she is effed up. You have to at least give me a
well,
chance
to well, what about
the,
you know, that one incident with that that chick that was really, really pissed off at you that one time?
What? Be more specific.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
You're talking in circles, Steven.
He
I
is.
Know.
I have
it's
no
called
idea.
Shitty improv.
I want to go
so
home.
Is that.
I want to go home.
Steve, come on.
Steve, what is going on? Come
please,
on, give
come
me a
on.
Chance to at least defend myself if you think I did something wrong. Go ahead.
You know, the incident with the, what's that blonde chick's name?
Don't help her. Jane Mansfield, who had better improv skills.
There's like 20 blondes on there.
I know.
I don't know. You have to tell me what
exactly.
you're talking about.
You know who she is. Don't ask her to admit it. You know.
I don't know. I don't know what
you were talking about it all fucking week.
Was I? I'm sorry, Jim. I'm having a lapse.
Steve, this is like really... Sucky. Tell
did
me what
Shauna,
you're talking about.
Did Shauna call a bellhop to bring all her baggage out with her? Could be a couple of trips.
Well, obviously,
see, Steve's not even letting me defend myself.
He's just, as soon as you leave, he'll start talking about it.
I know,
again.
And that's what makes
yes.
me upset, because then I won't be able to defend myself once
upset.
I'm gone.
Yes.
All right, Taya Parker, you're another terrific performance. A little different this time around, but it was great.
Yes, yeah. We are fans.
We
she's
certainly
fucking
are.
So hot, and you can
you.
See her on
Rock
and
Love
Bus. Brett's a great guest when he comes in.
Yep.
And... you can also see her today in Paramus, New Jersey, from
Paramus.
From noon to two.
I don't know how to say it.
At the Romantic
okay.
Depot, and you can meet Taya Parker.
You are.
I know. I should have cut that one joke sooner.
But I got greedy. I was trying to make up for the 45-minute lack of jokes we had as I was trying to get someone to improv.
That wasn't 45
did
minutes.
Did you know the thing with the girl?
All right. I want to thank the crowd for stopping by today. You saw a classic, that's for sure. You never know what you're going to see when you stop on by to this
is
show.
Like, this show is like the box of chocolates that Forrest's mother was talking about.
You never know what you're going to get.
Oh, yeah.
Yo.
That's it. And then she got the cancer on a Tuesday.
Tuesday.
That's right. And then the flying nun croaked. And Burt Reynolds showed up and put her back in the wedding dress and fucked her body along with Junior and Buford T. Justice. Boo. What a way to end on a fucking dud.
Oh, that's okay. We had a... We had a very exciting show today.
A lot
of drama, as they say.
A lot of drama.
In Paramus.
All right, let's get out of here. Taya, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thanks, everybody.
Else. We'll see you, I think, Tuesday. I think we're taking a long weekend. Next live show, Tuesday.
Oh, have a nice
Monday,
Valentine's
Monday,
Day.
We'll have some fine stuff from the past. See you guys.